world of Radio Shock Jocks, the biggest are Opie and Anthony.
These people say shocking things that border on offensive in order to entertain their audience.
I refuse to sit here and think that radio has to be nice. Why? Why does radio, out of any other medium, have to be nice? We are being now held to a standard where we have to be nice and make people feel good. Go screw!
Radio bad boys, Opie and Anthony.
Controversial radio personalities, Opie and Anthony.
Infamous DJs, Opie and Anthony.
Talk show radio hosts, Opie and Anthony.
Opie and Anthony.
Opie and Anthony.
Radio shock jocks, Opie and Anthony.
Opie and Anthony.
Shock jocks, Opie and Anthony.
Shock jocks, Opie and Anthony.
Dealing with a twisted testicle. She wrote out a prescription that basically said warm baths to let them float. They would look like alligator eyes popping out of the water. What's the best show on TV? I think it's called Three Sheets.
Where Anthony is in relation to the wind when he's driving.
I have a red light in my bathroom.
Wow.
For showering with a chick when you have a red light.
You're always thinking of how you can look a little better.
Exactly. So I have a blindfold. I hand a girl when she comes in.
The Opie and Anthony radio show, the most popular show in the history of satellite radio.
But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Hello, Opie and Anthony show.
Opie and Anthony show.
Hello.
That was a hell of a way to end a week last week. Wow.
That seems like days ago.
I know.
Because it was.
It was.
Yeah.
Well, I was just telling these guys, don't forget your building pass.
Yeah, huh? They frown on you losing your building pass or forgetting it.
Well, on Mondays, you know, you're a little...
groggy.
A little groggy. Still living the weekend.
Yeah.
And I ran out of my apartment without my my pass to get into this joint.
That's a no-no. You think it was bad over at XM with that one guy.
Oh, yeah. Now I love that guy.
Yeah.
I love the guy from XM.
Now he seems like Mr. Tolerant.
Oh, yeah.
He's Ted Tolerant.
All we want in this world is for somebody to give us a goddamn break.
A goddamn break.
I think if you break down life, that's all you want.
Yeah.
For someone to give you just a break. And I needed that break this morning, and this guy was like, no. Sorry. No, there's not even a sorry. No. No break for you.
No.
What's your name? What are you doing here? What company do you work for? And he left his post to go take care of my situation because I don't have a pass. And you just see like a Congo line of people walking into the building.
Just blowing past them?
Yeah, showing any IDs or nothing.
It's the typical, the cop pulls you over for speeding, and while you're sitting there, everyone else is speeding past the cop.
Yeah.
It's pretty much what happens. He singled you out.
Right.
You didn't have your pass. And then everybody else, pass or not, they're just blowing right past them.
You make a great point. Everyone's going 80, 85 right by you
yeah.
as you're getting the ticket because you're the bad guy.
Sitting there with the dumb look on your face. Yeah. You're just going, I'm the guy.
So he goes, well, give me your name. If you're in the system, I'll let you up.
Yeah.
So I tell him my real name. You're not in the system. I am in the system. No, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Yes, I am.
Here.
Right. And then Kenny, because Kenny gets frustrated, so he starts leaning over and he goes to the guy, you're not even spelling his name right.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah.
Ugh,
so then he spells it, you're not in the system. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Yes, it's just going back and forth like a cartoon. All of a sudden, Kenny leans over again. He's not a visitor. Like, the guy can't even get the basics down.
That's his job.
Right.
His job isn't just going, you don't have your pass. It's what to do when someone doesn't have the pass.
Correct.
In an expedient fashion.
Yeah.
Not just sit there and then clusterfuck the whole thing up trying to key in the wrong information.
Yeah.
God, what idiots these security guys are in 99% of the buildings.
And I just wanted to get upstairs. And I knew this was going to happen. I'm trying to get up here before, you know, the Stern people start heading into the building. Because it's like the first week where both camps are in the building. Sure enough, boy Gary walks in. He sees me at the front desk. He's pretty much laughing inside. I know. I'm not stupid. And then finally the guy lets me go. Perfect timing to take the elevator up with boy Gary.
Oh, yeah?
So now we get to do the old small talk.
Chit-chat?
The old chit-chat.
Old chit-chat.
He was fine, but, you know, there's no story to tell there. But The guy downstairs, what an ass.
I ran in and went into the elevator.
Yeah.
And then I hear other people. Like, I hear, good morning, good morning. And I'm like, door closed, door closed, door closed. Like, I don't want to ride up with anybody. I'm a single elevator guy. I'm just like.
And it's not that you're panicking over anything. You don't want to do that with the people that work on our show.
No, I don't want small talk.
With anyone.
None small talk.
Small talk sucks a big black cock.
Yeah, it does.
I hate small talk.
Chit-chat in the elevator. Stop it.
Chit-chat anywhere.
Stop it.
No small talk.
No.
If you want to talk a little politics, a little playoff hockey, a little golf, I'm right there with you. But this.
What about water cooler talk, Opie? Do you like water cooler talk? Oh, I would just talk about the water cooler. Isn't this water warm? Yeah. Shouldn't it be cooler water here at the cooler?
How did that come about? You think guys were just hanging out by the water cooler with their nice cool cup of water?
Yeah. How's Jesus. Your water? Great. How's yours? Delicious. You know, it's better than tap water.
Yeah.
Yeah, it always is. You know, the bubbles are funny, aren't they? No.
Just have barbaric water cooler chat, like dip your finger in the cup and go, I think Susan Smith backed her van into water that was colder than this.
Yeah, then how's the wife? How's the kids? How was your weekend?
How's your weekend? Hey, how about the game?
The big game.
I like talking about the game.
Right.
Right. Shop.
So there you go. I ain't forgetting my pass.
Small talk sucks the big black guy.
Oh, like,
well, I've never heard small talk attack so harsh.
Screw small talk.
Am I right, though? It's the worst. Yeah. I don't care where you are. When someone starts in with that small talk, you want to strangle them.
I've gotten to the point where I have to put everything I have to take to work on my keychain. So it's making my keychain very heavy. And then I have to put like this, you know, those little mountain climber clips that are all the rage?
Yeah.
I have to put that on my regular, my actual car keys so that when Kenny goes to get my vehicle, I could detach it from the multitude of crap that's now on my keychain.
That's smart.
Two of those things, because do you know there's two passes?
Yeah.
Yeah, what's the other pass for?
I don't know.
Just to make
it's upsetting.
Just to make it more of a hassle. One, that's all it's about.
Shut up.
One building
that should be turned down to zero.
There's a building pass and then there's the
what's the other pass?
The one that's just for Sirius. Like, the one says...
One's to get you in the building, the other one's to get you into this
Yeah,
facility.
But the one that gets you in the building just says tenant ID.
Mm-hmm.
And you hit that against the thing when you walk in. But then before you get to the elevators, you have to turn your tube card pass system around and dab the Sirius ID in the lobby before you get on the elevator.
Yeah.
So you take the elevator up, and then you have to keep the Sirius side of the two-pass system handy, because when you get off the elevator, there's normally a guard who you have to now hit your pass against the door before you get in.
It's so stupid.
What? I don't even understand that.
Could they put the code for the other one on the same
card?
Yes,
they certainly could.
So then it's a one-card system?
One card. Yes.
But why? They have to justify their dopey jobs down there? And by the way, getting back to my dumb little story, it was broken, and we just went into panic mode. And said, oh, I don't have my pass. I could have walked right through.
Yeah.
And it was obvious that it was broken. But I had to be stupid.
That's why, you know, all the criticism you gave to that other guy over there at the XM building.
I hate that guy still.
And I've waved every morning. He was very pleasant to me. I don't think I showed a pass for years walking past there. I don't think I had to sign in unless someone else was at the desk.
Mm-hmm.
You've got to make friends with these people.
I hate to tell you, one day you're going to forget it, and you're not going to be happy.
Oh, not downstairs. No, no, I know. I'll be very angry.
How are you a security guard, and you can't even spell?
Yeah, well...
So if there's a problem...
Could he speaky English?
I'll give him, like, 70%.
70?
Yeah.
Yeah.
A little messed up in the English department.
Little accent going on there. Yeah.
How bad was he spelling your name? Did Kenny say how he was spelling it?
I don't know.
Anthony Cumia. He was.
But Kenny was being professional, but very frustrated. That's not how you spell it. Well, he's not a visitor.
It's S W E E T I E P I E.
Yeah.
It's long, it's long spelling for a joke, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it's all right. Sometimes long spelling is what it takes.
Not this time, apparently.
I actually did. I hate to cry wolf. I didn't hear it because I just saw Craigslist killer Vic's handcuffed. And I just looked at that and I missed the spelling.
Oh, they got it?
No, I don't know. But they said that the Craigslist killer is handcuffed all through Victor.
They don't have that. They don't have that guy yet.
No, they don't.
That is a great video of him and everything.
I heard
in the lobby of that hotel.
I was reading about that. Bring everyone up to speed, Jimmy, because you got the article in front of you.
It's just a guy. He was killed. He shot a girl in Boston, which I think was a robbery gone wrong.
Did he shoot her in the hotel room?
I believe he did. Yeah, it was in a Marriott.
Yeah, I think they heard some screaming.
So that's what my guess is, that he was
screaming,
robbing
her. And shooting her, and no one next door is noticing that all hell's breaking loose?
Hotel. You think that it's a pay-per-view or something? Well, watching the latest action flick.
Oh, my God,
this,
right?
Yeah, that hot new movie, Don't Shoot Me, Sir. It was, I'm guessing, it was 20th floor. So I'm assuming that he went to rob her, maybe assault her or whatever. But when she screamed, he probably shot her, because you can't just run out of the room and leave the premises. You're on the 20th floor. Like in a motel, you can just get the fuck out of there. You scream and the guy can leave. But 20th floor, we're going to do ding. You know, she's fucking screaming, holy hell, in the room. Waiting for the elevator.
Was she an all-in prostitute, you think?
I don't know.
Because they're saying she was a model. She was beautiful.
Yeah, pretty
good. And she was doing some masseuses on the side, or massaging on the side.
What do you think, though? Come
on. The Craigslist.
She probably did something, yeah.
Yeah, she probably did a little of the, Jimmy's a pro on this, a little of the Yankee Cranky, you think?
I have to see her ad, but some of these girls fuck, and some of these girls just do a little bit of a hand release, and so, you know, it all depends on the girl and how much she's making. Yeah, some of them won't bang you. I mean, there are girls that just won't sell the pussy. They just won't do it. Like, for them, it's the hand, it goes no farther.
I think for the right price.
And most of them, I think you're right, you can.
You know, say $10, and they're all over it.
Well, I mean, if you want a weekend, I mean, you know.
And girlfriend experience.
Yeah.
And they're saying there's three of these incidents?
Yeah, where he...
This is the only one that's killed, though, right?
The only one that's dead. They said this Craigslist kill. He's used plastic handcuffs on all three of the women, and he's been on, like, a week-long spree, and they said it's the common link. This one girl, her name was Julissa Brisbane. It was, like, a bullet... Her body was bullet-ridden, and... You know, she was like an aspiring actress who offered sensual massages.
Yeah. What is an aspiring actress? I'm so sick of hearing that, too.
It's probably what she told
her
family.
This is Monday.
We're going to
bitch and complain a little bit today.
It's what you're doing when you're in jobs that can get you riddled with bullets.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Aspiring actress, that means nothing. Water cooler talk means nothing.
I'm an aspiring astronaut, by the way.
Yeah.
I'm a radio host, but I'm an aspiring astronaut. What are the odds?
I'm an aspiring golfer, so there you go.
There you go.
Still have a dream of making the, at this point, the senior tour.
You're going to...
Well, aspiring actress, here's the thing. She may have wanted to act... But to live in New York and make New York money, make rent, you have to have a job where you're making a decent amount of coin.
Sure.
What kind of job can you do where, like, you can make enough money to live in New York City, but still go on auditions and stuff like
that?
Yeah, it's fucking tough.
Yeah.
So it's possible.
Hey, at least they got that. You know, it's like if you're a guy and you're an aspiring actor, you got to wait tables.
Yeah.
You can't go, you know. Oh, male prostitute sounds fine if you think you're going to go out banging girls, but that just doesn't happen with guys.
John Voight showed us what happened when you try that.
Exactitica-tackily.
But I think you guys are missing the point. Aspiring actress means nothing. It should be trying to be an actress.
Yeah.
Wants to be an actress. Hoping to be an actress.
Yeah,
aspiring,
aspiring actress
means nothing.
And they use it in the paper all the time somebody's tragically killed.
All the time. If you have another one of these, give us a call, because I want to bitch about all of them. Hey, the one thing, Ant was sort of saying it, and then we went for the facts of the story. The guy just nonchalantly, after he killed her by shooting her a bunch of times, walks through the lobby like nothing.
Yeah, looks at the camera pretty much. They got a pretty good view of this guy.
I don't care what
white guy.
I don't care what the camera's saying. I mean, if you're that guy walking through that lobby, you're like, all right, be cool, be cool. All right, all right, be cool. What are you doing? Don't look over there. Just walk.
Turn your head a little bit.
Right. Just look at the front door. Get to the front door. Get to the front door.
It's like this place with the cameras all over the place. You just put my head down and walk out. Just in case David's bullet-riddled body is found.
Yeah, you got to make...
Aspiring douchebag. He made it.
You got to make believe there's not 10 cameras on you at every time.
Yeah.
Every single moment. What's that about? Who's the paranoid guy around here?
They don't want any pilfering. Is it for pilfering of paper clips?
I don't know.
Or is it for workplace violence and harassment? Like, what is the what are the reasons for so many cameras in this joint?
I don't know.
The other place only had them out in the hallway, and that was because the building didn't trust us. There was always nude women running to the bathroom, getting us in trouble.
Sometimes
covered in, or nude gentlemen.
Well, the nude women.
Tippy Tom.
Bloody running out of the building. That was always a treat for the rest of the people that worked in that building, huh?
Oops. Yeah.
We should set that up today. Bloody girl, fake blood running through the lobby of this building.
Yeah,
give him a big how you do today.
That'll get us thrown out.
Yeah, I know. Can't have fun anymore.
No, there's no real fun in the hallways. We give it a shot, but
Speaking of harassment, I was watching cop videos last night on YouTube.
Yeah.
Because of what I was telling you. Maybe I'll bring it up later. Whatever. I was really fast. I was down in Philly. It was a story we covered last May. There were
a story you heard here first.
I think there were two or three guys that were beat up pretty good by cops. They were being kicked about, and they had helicopter footage of the guys. It was a big, huge story in Philly. Actually, went
busy
national.
Body helicopter.
It went national. I was at a party on Saturday with one of the guys that was part of that incident, and had to take the fall for the incident and lost his job.
Really? Yeah.
And he even said, "Look," he explained who he was on the video. And I was able to see which one he was. And he did exactly what everyone else was doing.
He's a YouTube sensation.
Oh, yeah, he is. He goes, you'll see me on the video.
Yeah.
I don't want to blow up his spot because there's a pretty big case going on about this whole thing. But he lost his job. And they decided to, you know, have him take the fall and another guy. And that was it. Even though it was like 13 or 15 guys or something like that, all doing the same thing.
Uh-huh.
Bunch of horse shit, to be honest with you. But it's kind of like our situation. Just fire everybody. And you know, cover your own ass.
Yeah.
He's like a huge fan of the show, which, you know, whatever. But then I went and saw that video, which led me to more cop videos.
Yeah, yeah, they're so much fun.
Have you guys seen, and it has like 8 million views, the woman that's at the police station, and maybe Danny can find it.
Is it the one that's sitting there and then gets up in the guy's face and falls over?
Well, basically the story goes, this girl has a very tiny, like... jean skirt on. Really, it looks like she's put together nice. It's hard on these, like, you know, these videos, obviously. Yeah. And then they pixelate her face, but she looks really hot. And the person she was with got pulled over for drunk driving. But she was okay. So they brought her to the station as well. And now she needs a ride home. So she's there for a couple hours. It's like 4 in the morning. And the cops are just like kind of doing a little squeezy,
a little grab ass,
and then she's like getting up on the counter and stuff, and I guess she doesn't have underwear on, and the cops are coming out and they're snapping pictures with their cell phones.
Oh, I didn't see that one. No,
the perv switch must have went off because they all know there's cameras there, and they got caught on the surveillance cameras, and a bunch of guys got fired for this incident. But the video's it's okay because it's surveillance footage. It's
grainy.
But you can see what they're doing. She goes in the back room, and one of the guys like lifts her skirt up as she's going into the other room. And
dude, she was so, that was such a sexy video.
Wow.
You could picture yourself.
You've seen it?
Oh, yeah. With the girl who was, those cops got fired.
Yeah.
It was.
I don't know how you find it, Danny.
If you put drunk girl on.
Drunk?
Drunk girl stripping in police station or something, like she was. You'll find she's not hard to find, but she was super sexy, man. It was the idea that we've all seen a girl that drunk, and like you just know you can reach under her skirt and touch her ass, and you won't get yelled at.
It's really hot, man. This might be it right here.
Oh, police tape released. Yeah, it's some news footage, I guess. Yeah, they're just having a little fun.
You know what? Yeah, this girl.
Oh, wow.
She's got the big white boots on, tiny little skirt, white shirt, dark hair.
I'm in love with her.
Yeah, there's something really, you got to be honest, there's something really hot about this.
What have we got here?
Her alcohol consumption.
Yeah, oh yeah.
I don't think she was complaining about the attention she was getting.
Look at this Club Soda Kenny looking guy.
Yeah.
With his beady eyes.
He has to be, and she just puts on.
Oh, look at what she's doing. Come on, she's got a leg up on the counter, one leg.
One leg way up on the counter. Watch when she goes in the back room, man. We'll give you the link to this
video.
She's
asking for it.
Watch, look, a little grab ass.
Look, she's backing up. She's holding on to the door jamb.
And backing
her ass up. A cop's behind her.
She's pressing on his dick.
Yeah, she's backing up, lifting the skirt up.
Yeah.
How do you not touch her? She's so hot.
There's something really hot
about
this. She's
laying on the counter.
Yeah.
Oh, come on,
dude. As she leans over, her tiny little skirt pops up even more.
Yeah.
Now she's on all fours on the top of the counter.
The cop with the cell phone camera
just walks
out. I needed photographic evidence
You think that's what his...
it had to be.
Yeah, I was just trying to get evidence. Yeah.
Look at these other guys behind the counter. They're taking pictures. She's lifting her skirt up. I guess it's inappropriate behavior for the station.
You have to fire them, though. God, take a guy's fucking pension. Fucking assholes.
Yeah.
It's obvious she wanted it.
She's being a whore.
She did, though, but it's not like they attacked her. It's like, what do you do? You're a fucking bunch of guys.
Yeah.
We trust these guys to carry guns. You need testosterone to do that. You know, and a chick shows her ass. They're not supposed to look at it?
Yeah. Cops do have a...
What's the link to that, Danny, for the people that haven't seen it yet?
It's on YouTube.
I know.
It's if you search police take advantage of a drunk girl.
Yeah. Oh, come on.
But why do they always make those titles so vague?
Can't really figure out what's going on in the video.
Yeah.
Right.
That's fantastic.
Mm-hmm. Mike T in Jersey. Opie, I work at New Jersey Transit Rail Center in Kearney. Same idiots here, same S. Oh, same shit. I forget sometimes we're just on the satellite right now.
Yeah.
Open the trunk. What's your pass number? Same as yesterday. You're not on the list. Employee ID. Why are you here? And the security guards here are all ex-cons anyway, so.
Ex-cons. It's wonderful.
They just get a little power and they have to, like, they have to make your life miserable.
Wonderful.
Sounds like a badge bunny. Mike T in Jersey again.
Badge bunny?
Yeah, two for two for Mike T.
A lot of cop groupies, chicks try to get out of tickets.
What was the bull riding?
Beautiful girls.
And there's a name for all of them. What? Remember when I went to that bull riding and buckle bunnies? Are they? What was it called again?
Oh yeah, right. Because the big belt buckles that the cowboys wear. Are they buckle bunnies?
Yeah, there's a name for the girls that are hitting on the riders in the
Y'all know
the bull riding
lot lizards
league.
Or the trucker girls.
Right, right.
And those are probably the bottom of the barrel.
No, you got to think.
Comedians, groupies are fat men. Probably buckle bunnies. It sounds right.
I forget. There was a name. It must be.
I have. Have you ever? Not ever, but when you're watching Cops, or one of those police shows where they're doing a sting operation on prostitution, you ever see attractive prostitutes on that show? It's amazing how many, like, old, cracked out, toothless bitches are on those shows.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh yeah, we've arrested you before. You're familiar.
Oh, I was just out here. It's your friend. I was talking in the window.
And they got the big sunken in lips because with the wrinkles around them.
How bad do you need a blowjob?
I know.
That's a little rough.
That's what I'm thinking. Look at
that's a little rough.
These are prostitutes.
Yeah.
Danny's scrolling through the real prostitutes that you get. Wow.
Oh,
God.
My God.
Holy shit. It looks like Opie. Go up a little.
No, God, that's terrible.
You know, you're kind of right, though. They're all aspiring actresses,
where
too.
Where is a hot one? There's nothing there.
Oh, my God.
That's the disaster. Right there is the typical one you see on Cops. She's probably only in her 40s. She looks 60 and has no teeth.
Wow. Looks like Joe Dirt's mother.
Yeah, nice mullet.
Big mullet.
Yeah, soccer mom looking
would
thing.
Would you do any of these?
No.
No. There was one white chick back that was maybe a five back up a few.
Danny, where are you looking for this, too? Trying to keep everyone involved today.
Just Google ugliest prostitutes.
Oh, really?
Nice.
Can you imagine being told you made that list?
Yeah. Congrats. Oh, man. Wow, look at the brows on her. That is horrendous. That one might have youth on her side.
Yeah, there's a little youth going on there.
She's also got a shanker on her chin.
Yeah, that's a... She's probably fell on a curb, though.
A rough ball bag hit her. Someone with some stubble coming in.
I hit the bottom of her chin. They must have been a couple of low hangers.
Wow, 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 wow.
Ugly as hookers. I know. Prostitutes. Hey, you made it.
Did you get congratulated on that because you made A-list?
Yeah.
Oh, 400, ugliest prostitute.
Yeah.
You made it.
Amazing.
That's wonderful.
Hey, 10 years ago today.
Yeah.
Columbine.
Uh-huh.
Is that amazing?
How
is that 10 years ago?
Yeah. I heard that on the news coming in, and I was like, for some reason, that one didn't get me as much as some other things where it's like, wow, because that does kind of seem like a while ago.
Columbine seems a while ago?
Yeah, it kind of seems like a while ago.
Oh, I don't know. Not for me.
But
it seems like yesterday, which means it's Hitler's birthday,
what means,
right?
Yes, happy birthday to you. Jesus. Would have been 110 years young today, I believe.
Isn't this a bad day to go to school?
420.
420 is a bad day to do stuff, right?
It's also the smoke pot day.
Right.
420 day, man. So you smoke some weed. A lot of stuff about 420. Yeah, it's a big day for white supremacists and the sort. I got later on Steve from Bayshore is coming over the house. We're going to go down in the theater and watch some old World War II footage, followed by Downfall, the movie Downfall, about Hitler in the bunker and the last days of him, his
nice.
Staff, and Ava and Goldie.
That's nice. Celebrate.
Well, it's not much a celebration as a look back in history. It would be very inappropriate, Jimmy, to celebrate a man's birthday like Adolf Hitler.
Did you call Carvel and try to get a cake with 6 million candles? Grape.
No. It's a look back to put in perspective where we were and where we are.
A look back would be if you did it on April 28th. If you do it on the day that Hitler was born, you are embracing,
exactly.
You're celebrating, you're blowing out candles like Jimmy.
No, there will be no cake.
You two in party hats with a fucking cider.
I do not get cake. I never get to cake. That's why I
a look back
piece of cake.
Would be if you did this any other day of the year.
Yep.
You had a plan ahead and go, ooh, his birthday's coming up. What should we do this year?
You pick a day in history that is relevant to what you're going to be watching, mm-hmm. and experiencing and thinking about and pondering, things like that. So this day was a day where it's like, okay, we need to remember history so we do not repeat history, Opie. So what I like to do... No, that cake, Danny, will not be at my house. It's a giant. There are three people carrying out a giant swastika cake back in the 30s.
Why don't
I
they
believe.
Make that type of cake on those dumb cake shows?
Yeah, where do you go?
You see on the Food Network.
For that cake.
They should have. That's a cake show I would watch. Outrageous cakes. But
they just make horrible,
horrific,
tasteless cakes.
Yeah, horrific, tasteless
about
cakes.
About miscarriages and stuff. Just need a lot of Cherry's Jubilee on top of it.
Where are we at with our... Where are we at with our most offensive song thing?
Because there's some. Never shall we ever do it again. What?
Well, can we play the ones we used to play? Where are we
nine.
At with that?
Nine.
You don't think so? How the hell did we ever get away with that?
I don't know. And that was on regular radio.
Regular radio.
quite amazing, to tell you the truth. Yeah, there's another birthday cake. That looks a little more modern. That one doesn't look like it was done in the 30s.
I can't see
it.
It
was from a few years ago. It says, happy 116th birthday, Adolf Hitler.
116th? Jeez. I thought it would only be 110.
Oh. Like 116th to me.
Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it was 120.
I hear 120 years ago today.
All right, then it's 120.
It's a big one, Ann.
Oh, how can
I forget? Been 120 if he was still
120.
Living.
120.
He's probably dead.
Yeah, he probably is.
You know he didn't live healthy.
No, he didn't.
Probably ate sauerkraut, didn't sleep properly.
He was a vegetarian, by the way, Adolf Hitler. A vegetarian.
Yeah.
I guess he lost his flavor for meat. We saw what his military was doing.
I guess that blows Bernie Goetz's theory out of the water that vegetarians are more docile.
And less violent of a person.
Either that or how big a prick would he have been if he ate burgers?
Yeah. I picked the wrong day. Stephen S. from Bayshore writes, well, actually, Opie, April 28th would be a celebration, too. That's the anniversary of Hitler's marriage to Eva, 2 days before they killed themselves in the bunker.
Ah, yes.
Here's to the happy couple.
It seems to just be, April is a big Hitler month, I do believe.
Great.
And my birthday falls in there, too, in between all the shenanigans.
Your birthday's Sunday.
I'm in there.
Happy birthday.
Yeah.
Sunday.
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 Sunday, Sunday, Sunday.
Cool.
Yeah, I just, you know, I don't like doing much on that.
On your birthday?
No, I'm not one of those, like, make a big deal out of it kind of a thing. I like just hanging out.
Well, Sunday.
What hour?
Sunday is your low-key day, so it's perfect for you.
Hopefully it'll be nice. I'm so sick of New York and Northeast weather. I don't know about the rest of the country, but we got a nice day Saturday. It was
80.
Poof, it was like 80 degrees. Was able to go out back and just hang out. So nice.
What, Jimmy?
I'm sorry. It was 80 degrees, and I checked my iPhone, and my girlfriend's like, "How cold is it?" I'm like, 45. And so we went out to get coffee, and she had on a sweater and her scarf and a jacket.
I
got her so good.
What a great gag.
She was fuming.
You are a tool. It's blazing hot out. Yeah.
That's a perfect gag for New York City because, you know, we don't have the luxury of the suburbs where you could kind of feel that it might be warm outside.
Yeah.
You're stuck in your glass box here in Manhattan. You don't know if it's 80 or 30 outside.
And if you're going down like 50 floors right. in an elevator, by the time you get outside, you're not going to go back up again.
That's great.
What a good gag.
No, rules.
You're a prick.
Because you're literally people like kids on their bikes in short sleeves, and she has like an ascot.
A scarf.
That's great.
It was a beautiful day, you know, one of those days where you could just hang out back, drink, whatever, have a good time. Yeah. And then today, 45 is the high, rain. We are getting no spring right here. This is cutting into valuable like springtime.
We haven't had spring in years. It goes from that weird winter to summer.
Dude, it's so much worse this year. It really is worse because I remember at least it getting into mid-April and you'd start feeling maybe 2 days, 3 days in a row mm-hmm. where it's nice out. Now it's just, you know, it's coming up on like middle to the end of April. And it's still shit out.
April showers.
May flowers.
Yuck. I'll add that to my list. April showers.
They bring
May flowers. Aspiring actress. And what is the other one? Oh, yeah. Water cooler talk.
Water cooler talk. Is there a water cooler here? I just want to go near it and start talking.
Holy crap. Let's have Sam hang out by the water cooler all day. Yeah.
And do water cooler talk. What is that? A real doll or something on the news? I'm seeing there. People are probably outraged that there's a semi-clad, big-titted mannequin.
Those things are starting to look real.
And it's on the side of the road.
Can we find out what that story's about?
Yeah, I'm sure
it looks like the famous real dolls.
Interesting. That
you've heard about over the years, and she's a buxom like blonde.
Yeah, that's ridiculous, though.
And her bikini's on, and her boobies are, like, you know, popping out all over the place. Her perfect real doll boobies.
Would you bang one of those things?
Yeah.
In a second?
I didn't have to think about it.
I wasn't even going to say, like, oh, you would?
Yeah.
I was like, I'd be inside.
It would be so creepy.
You'd be balls deep in it, and then when you come, you'd feel like an idiot. What is that?
Well,
what happens to your brain after you shoot?
Yeah.
It's just like, it really is just an on-off switch.
It's like your brain yells, cut, and you're back to normal.
And you're back to normal what kind of a creep am I?
Who is he?
Then everything just gets awkward immediately.
Yeah, it really is something.
The real doll.
Yeah, his men real doll.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, God. Just put that in your living room. It's some male doll with his shirt off. He's got his shorts on, pulled down a little, and this real doll dick sticking out.
And not an impressive one, I might add.
No, that's your
abs.
Average
would you do that
male,
as a goof?
Real doll.
It's not really a male.
What?
Just throwing the question out there.
That's actually funny. Would you fuck a real male doll? That's a good question.
Like flip it over and do it in the ass?
Yeah, and would
and kiss it.
Because it would feel no different than the female real doll.
Would that be considered gay?
Wow, we are all just silent here thinking about it.
Because you go,
all right, there you go. When you do that,
there it is. There is a male real doll.
Looks like your bathroom, by the way.
His name is Charlie.
Hey, wait a minute. That is my bathroom.
Hey, that's not a real doll.
Hey, get off that picture.
It's a real doll, and it's bent over the edge of the tub. It's kneeling in the bathtub, a little bubble bath thing going on. There's a few soapy suds on his glistening back, and it is in perfect position to get in the tub and rail in the hiney hole. But again,
the soapy.
Would you do that? Because it is exactly the same material as the female real doll.
So is it real life.
Yes.
An asshole's an asshole.
Oh, God. Jesus, Danny. What?
Now it's sitting on the edge of the tub with a close-up to its schween. What the hell? What the hell?
You would go?
No. I'm saying, what the hell would you?
I don't know. That's a little rough, to be honest with you.
It's all you've had, except your hand. All right.
I don't mind.
You lost your arms in a horrible accident. You can't jack off. Mm. It's all there is laying around the house is a male doll, a real doll. Nice, slippery asshole available.
I'm not playing this game. How long do you think I've been around, you idiot?
What? You don't want to hear the, you homo, after you answer yes?
We started this game together. That would be a little rough.
That's a little rough, yeah.
I used to build women when I was like, you know, starting off my jerking off.
Grave robbing? How'd you build them?
Ah, you use pillows and stuff.
Oh, things like that?
Yeah. That's why doing a real doll of the female variety would be very easy. You didn't build a woman when you were growing up, Morris?
No, I did not.
I never called it building a woman. I just, like,
Hispanic, right?
Shit to...
Yes.
That's why.
Exactly.
Hispanics.
Just fuck plantains.
Hispanics were thrown into that sex world nice and early. Did you shower with dad?
Stepped out of something that could have got me in trouble, see?
Oh,
I want people to know when I use my mental filter. It's like instead of making a fake woman, building a woman,
yeah,
he would just them. You know.
Oh.
Well, you can think up whatever word you want. But it's a horrible, horrible depiction of Hispanic people that I did not want on the air.
How much? How much are they, Danny? Some of these are fucking amazing.
Oh yeah, we've talked to this guy over the years.
Pretty pricey. I think they're like $6,000 or something like that.
Oh my god, really? Yeah. $6,000 to fuck something that doesn't change shape?
You make your money back in a few prostitution deals you might have done, a few dates you might have gone on.
There's a shemale option. Alone.
A shemale option. Yeah. Well, punch that up.
Yeah, $6,500 plus, I guess, shipping.
Would you do the shemale real doll?
No.
In a pinch?
Nah, that's rough.
Let's see. What do they look like? I guess they're just the female ones with a dick.
Yeah, with a cock on them.
All right. Then you got to do it in the ass, right?
Yeah, you're
not giving it a reach around. It's a doll. You don't have to make it feel good.
Trannies, shemales, no way.
But it's not a tranny. It's a female real doll with a plastic...
Because it comes down to this. You could smell male.
Yeah, but not on the real doll.
Oh, that's a good point.
I'm talking about the real doll. Not really. In real life? Screw that. I'm talking... No, screw that, but forget that. The real doll is nothing but a female real doll with an appendage. And I guess authentic anal features. Now, you're not giving it a handy because you don't have to make it feel good. To me, I would equate that to a woman who likes just putting a strap on, but doesn't want to do you with the strap on, and then you bang her in the ass while she's wearing a strap on.
Would your girlfriend get mad though? Like,
what is
all
that?
Right, all right, look, it does have plastic balls.
That's a real doll?
That's a real doll tranny?
No, that's a chick.
It looked like it had balls.
It doesn't have a cock. That's a chick.
Oh, okay. I had that all mixed up for all these years? Jesus, I better switch back. Ow.
How do you look at that?
I wonder it's so hard to sit down every day.
All right.
Look how they can pose them in all kinds of various real-life positions.
The problem is they don't have the eyes right yet.
No, that's kind of creepy looking at those lifeless dead eyes like a doll's eyes.
Because the eyes makes it look like you're banging a corpse.
Yeah.
Problem is, where do you put them when company comes over?
In the closet. They're a little big to just kind of stash somewhere. Mm-hmm. And if you want to show people your house, put it under your bed. That's kind of creepy.
Imagine.
Can you pose them, Danny?
Yeah, I think they're like fully poseable.
Yeah, you move them around.
I've seen documentaries where like guys are obsessed with these things.
Yeah, I saw that one on HBO.
Real Sex.
Real Sex. It's an old documentary, but it's so creepy. Remember the couple that wanted to have the threesome? So they got the real doll and brought it in the pool with them, and it just looked so silly. Mm-hmm. She's licking box on a fucking, you know.
I remember
it's
that.
Like you might as well get the wax lips, turn them sideways, and start licking them.
I think I also remember there was like an English documentary where this guy, like he didn't have any money. Obviously there was something a little wrong with him, but like he spent all his money on real dolls, and he had like four or five of them.
Yeah,
and he would dress
them
up, and he'd like his day was spent with the dolls, and he'd like pretend that they were his friends and stuff. Very, very strange.
Blue Healer from Kentucky writes: "Stick to your guns, Opie. Don't fuck anything with a dick."
Well, he makes a point, regardless of if it's a rubber one on a rubber doll or a real one.
All right. Okay. Gordon from Jersey. How shameful would you feel cleaning your load out of its ass after you're done?
See, that's just it. That's the switch in your head. You'd be all revved up and frothing and grunting as you're just pounding away. And the second you shot your load and you know you got to clean it up, there it is, just like this rubber man ass.
How do you clean it out, though? Like, what do you do?
I don't give a garden hose. I don't know what you're going to do.
In the mouth and it comes out the toes?
Yeah. I guess you got to get in there with some kind of cleaning solution.
And by the way, I like the fact you asked the question before, like, if you had no arms, would you, like, if you had no arms, like, that's your big dilemma. Like,
well,
I can't dial 911, I can't eat, but do I want to stick my dick in this male rubber doll?
In a fake man. Yeah. Well, I had to put the scenario out there.
If you had no arms.
If you had no arms and no feet.
Like if you went to pick up important documents in platoon.
This is important. Get me a male real doll.
How silly would you feel trying to nudge it over on its stomach? It's hard on is keeping it pressed up.
Keeps tipping over. Dick falls out.
The Asian one, they bring an extra penis. It comes in a matchbox.
We got one story to do here. On the phones, we got Ray in Philly.
Hello, Humpy and Anthony show.
Good morning, boys.
Good morning, Ray.
Hey, my aunt was in a mall.
You could call me Ray. You could call me Jay. You could call me Ray J. Johnny. But she doesn't have to call me Johnson. Ugh. That should have been killed years ago.
You didn't like that bit?
Oh, that bit was horrid.
It was all right.
Ray J. Johnson.
Every time you called him Ray, he would just jump. Hey, you could call me. Got it.
Well, what, Mr. Johnson? You doesn't have to call me Mr. Johnson. You could call me Ray. Or you could. Yes, we get it.
Can we try to figure out the worst comedy sketch ever?
That's it.
Not comedy sketch. The worst comedy stand-up comedy bit ever. Like, the one Ant just described, the Ray is right up there.
Horrific.
See, the only problem is we probably don't know it because it's probably so bad it never got famous.
No, it's one of those that is over the top famous for...
Jiffy Jeff's Gym.
That's a Nelson bit.
Yeah.
I'm familiar with the character. I don't know the bit.
Yeah.
Yes.
Maybe we'll try to figure that out. What the fuck are we looking at?
Video of a man actually having sex with a real doll?
Yeah, he's face-fucking a real doll.
Let me see it, Dan. Turn a little bit.
He's face-fucking it.
What the f-
No money shot? Fuck. Why I?
Where's this, Dan?
This is a website called realdollsex.com.
Why does he keep the shirt on it?
Yeah, right? He's trying to be sexy.
How do you keep a rod for a real doll?
I guess friction.
There's the money shot you wanted.
Oh, there's the money shot all over the cans.
All over the big plastic boobies.
See, now he's got to wipe it off.
That's called being in a hurry and not wanting to get in there with the fucking... He doesn't want to wrap toilet paper on his finger and scoop it in.
And start wiping out, hoping he got it all. Yeah, because you don't clean them out. You got a bunch of potato flakes.
Yeah, I was trying to get potato flakes on your real doll. Your real doll's got dandruff in between. Right.
These fuckers are funny this morning, especially. Hold on, Ray. Blue Healer in Kentucky writes, horrify the neighbors, hose off your real doll on the front lawn.
That's funny.
That is good. What are you doing, Bob? I'm just cleaning my cum out of this rubber doll.
Can I borrow your hose?
That's funny.
People say worst comedy bit ever. Kevin Meaney's We Are the World.
You know what, though? That was relevant when it came out. It was kind of funny because he would, you know.
It was good when he first started doing it.
When it first started. We you didn't see need it
to
now.
Hear, we didn't need to hear it 20 years later.
Oof.
Hey, Ray, go ahead. Finally. Sorry.
Sorry, not Ray. Right.
Hey. So my aunt was sitting in a mall, I guess it was a couple months ago, and she saw some guy standing in the the front of the mall where the mannequins are. He's groping and humping the back of the mannequin in front of the in front of all the people in the mall. I guess he had Down syndrome or something. Oh, it was, he was sitting there going to town on this thing.
Yeah, they'll jerk off at the drop of a hat.
Yeah, they really will. Literally.
A big, giant hat.
A hat with a propeller on it.
Some of those mannequins, though, growing up, you would kind of look at them a little odd when you were a kid.
Do you get sort of turned on when you see some of those mannequins without the clothes on?
When they first came out with the nipple ones.
The newer ones are, there's something going on.
But as a kid, that's when they first came out with, like, using the nips, and they'd have, like, very loose-fitting clothes, but it would be just gently brushing the mannequin nipple. And they were able to pose them differently. Because at first they were just creepy old-looking mannequins like at the nuclear test sites in Nevada. The ones that occupy the house that's going to blow up.
Crash test dummies.
Yeah, crash test fucking dummies. But you kind of started looking at them and going like, ooh, it's kind of nice.
not too shabby.
You combine the real doll with robotic technology that the Japanese are coming out with. Say within 50 years, there will be absolutely realistic where you can program, say, 50 personalities into it.
Yeah.
And it won't be able to walk and talk, like, just per se, but
punch in cunt. Just not give you any sex and just be a bitch.
Just roll over. But I guarantee you that there's realistic fuck dolls within X amount of time. And then the moral things will come up. How old should you make them? Can you make them as kids? Can you hurt them? All this weird shit's going to crop up.
I have heard about that, too, about the controversy of real dolls being made into obviously too young of a form, and whether that's some kind of a moral dilemma.
Well, who makes them? Like, you got to think, who's the guy that goes to the factory and makes that mold? Like, that's got to be a business that's probably targeted.
Yeah, they showed it in the documentary. They showed how they were made and everything. A fuckload of latex, man.
Yeah.
What? You have a latex allergy. You just come into work the next day covered in hives.
Yeah.
Dick is falling off.
Can we take a break? Because we got Sam went to the Chiller Theater. Chiller convention.
Oh, did he? That
Chiller
was going on?
Right? He interviewed our old pal Iron Sheik. The Iron Sheik. So we got a couple minutes of audio from the Iron Sheik.
Fantastic.
Also, Chris in Albany is giving us a heads up this morning. He says, you have to get some audio of Ralph Kiner from the Mets games.
Kiner's corner.
Unbelievable.
Is he still alive?
Kiner.
If you guys could get a couple clips from Ralph Kiner this year, that'd be
good. It's a new show called Kiner's Coroner. It's going to be, no? That was kind of funny. He's getting old and he'll be dead soon.
He got a double, Sam. 15 times he's 9.
We got to acknowledge that Harry Callis died.
Yes.
And I was down in Philly, and it's all about Harry Callis.
Speaking of Callis, now, Charlie Callis had a horrible bit, too. That was the comedian that went.
What was his bit?
I did a, he would just talk and go like.
I did a movie with him, and he was a very famous guy. I don't know what he does.
He would make stupid faces and sounds. Look, Kenny's laughing. Kenny looked like he was probably a Charlie Callis fan.
Who wasn't back in the day?
Who wasn't? You know, everyone. But he was always on these variety shows. Him and the Ray J. Johnson guy, they were always on these Dean Martin variety shows and Bob Hope. Hey, we got Ray J. Johnson coming out with Charo.
Oof. Would he come out and just do his bit?
Of course. Hey, Charlie Callis is coming out in a little while.
I need to see Charlie Callis now.
Was it a funny bit?
No! Stunk! It's terrible.
Where's Charlie Callis? That guy's fucking that real doll well.
Oh, yeah. He's deep dicking that fucking rubber woman.
Just like every woman ever fucks. She's just not moving, waiting for it to be over.
That is some weird shit.
How do these guys keep rods? I could never keep a rod.
You know what it is? It looks like it's very lubed. Yeah. I mean, he's not having any resistance problems. So it's probably just the physical sensation that this guy's into.
No emotional attachment there. He's spanking. He's spanking it, which is silly.
Well, we'll watch this guy fuck the real doll. We're going to take a break. We got to get Charlie Callis his picture up so we know who you're talking about.
You know what he should do? He should spray that fucking shit spray in its asshole before so at least you get a realistic scent. Right.
Put sushi in the vagina.
Just put some fucking tuna roll in there. Oh, goddamn.
What? All right. That is weird.
Fantastic.
That's weird.
Weird stuff.
He's lubing up his.
He has the money shot.
Nah, there's still more video.
Oh, is there? Oh no, he's just lubed it up, and now he's going back in.
Where's I want to see Charlie Callis.
We'll do that after the break. How's that?
Does.
But Charlie Callis stinks.
Hit me with a break. We'll continue. Opie and Anthony and little Jimmy Norton. That's right. You're checking out the Opie and Anthony show. Madonna on the front page of the paper today.
Oh, yeah?
Nothing to see there. She fell off a horse. Who cares? No
Big
injuries.
Whoop.
I say who cares because it shouldn't be on the front page.
Yeah.
I guess the paparazzi scared the horse or something.
The paparazzo.
But no real injuries. But
no.
We'll be hearing about this all day long.
All day long. She, she was riding. I think she probably took a dive. She took the dive to make the paparazzo look silly.
You think?
Yeah.
You think?
To get them in trouble. There hasn't been any good paparazzi stories. She's lucky, though. Could have ended up like Christopher Reeve. Isn't her daughter looking very much like her in the old days?
Yeah, absolutely.
That's all I'm saying.
And the daughter's only 12, by the way, looking a lot older than 12.
What are you saying?
I'm just saying.
I was just saying. What are you saying?
I'm just saying. Just saying.
Would you?
Sam.
Would you? Not yet.
Sam. Help me out here, Sam.
Sam.
Hi. Sam was at the Chiller Convention over the weekend.
What's going on over there?
Well, a lot of celebrities from Hollywood.
All right, hold the phone with celebrities.
Yeah, give us a list of people you saw at this horse shit.
Yeah.
Well, it was in Parsippany, New Jersey.
That's Mecca for celebrity sightings, by the way.
Yeah. And it featured such celebrities as Mickey Dolenz from the Monkees was there.
Wow. Mickey Dolenz, you said?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
He was the cool one in the Monkees.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I got my photo taken with Tony Curtis.
Stoney Curtis. That was him in the Flintstones. Hi, I'm Stoney Curtis.
For 120.
Can I stay at the house? Spartacus.
Hated that fucking show.
Yeah.
Flintstones ruled.
I liked the first season. Then they started getting a little silly. Once they brought the Great Kazoo in, I was out. First season was very funny.
How many seasons were there?
18. I have no idea.
It's one of those shows you think it had like 10 or 12 seasons. And
it was like two.
Three. Yeah,
three
yeah,
seasons.
Yeah. Something dumb.
Just in reruns forever and ever.
What else there, Sam? Tony Curtis is a big one, I guess.
Tony
sure.
Curtis was big. He's
yeah,
little...
he was big. That's like, you know, these Chiller Theater conventions aren't having as many people, it seems, that you kind of want to get autographs from.
Well, I mean, you don't get that many opportunities to meet Tony Curtis.
That's true.
You probably won't get that many more later.
Jamie Lee Curtis's father, by the way.
Is he looking old?
It's true.
Yeah.
Look at me like I'm a fucking half,
I had no
half
idea.
A fag over
no,
here.
No, that's not it.
You didn't know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Yes.
What do I know about Tony Curtis?
His last name is Curtis and so is hers.
Lots of people.
That's about it.
That's an easy one. Yeah. If you're going to be hobnobbing with the celebs, you should know a little bit about them.
You should have said, Tony, really, what is that thing between your daughter's legs? Please tell us. Yeah. We've been hearing rumors forever.
Yeah.
Rumors she was born a man, yeah. Sam.
That's what I've heard.
She's got a cock.
Or maybe had both.
For $125, you could buy a painting of Stoney Curtis and have it signed by Tony Curtis.
Wait, no, stop.
I swear.
You're not joking?
No, I swear.
He was actually playing off the whole Stoney Curtis thing.
Yeah.
You could get all the movies he's made and everything, but that was kind of the big get.
Well, I had an 8x10 from Spartacus signed.
Oh, you did? Okay.
Yes, but there was the option of paying $125 to get a painting of Stoney Curtis.
Is it an original cell?
No, it was a painting on canvas.
That sucks.
I know. I don't know anyone would buy it.
Jesus. Fuck him.
But
fuck him and the horse he rode in on.
How much was the picture?
It was only $25. It's a pretty good deal for Tony Curtis.
Yeah, sure.
Is it?
George A. Romero, Peter Criss.
Mm-hmm.
Those are big names. A lot of people from the Italian zombie movies were there. There's a whole section, the Italian section of zombie, but I didn't know them.
Really?
Yeah. Lou Ferrigno was there.
All right, that's big.
Yeah.
What was he doing? Besides staring at the phone like you had no idea what it was. Did they fix this, Mars?
What's the matter? So your mic arm is a little squeaky.
That's all right. I like to move around a lot. I feel like I don't want to interrupt everybody.
I was talking to Big Kev, who was there, believe it or not. The Big Kev.
No way.
Yeah. And the original Ronald McDonald was scheduled to be there.
Scheduled to.
Yeah, yes. But his hard drive was taken by the FBI. Couldn't make it.
Well, I don't know. Big Kev said the rumor was that while he was on his way to Chiller Theater, he had a heart attack and died.
That sounds like a rumor.
I didn't see anything on the news that the original Ronald McDonald died.
But sounds like a work.
There was Jan Brady from the Variety Show.
Holy shit! I was just gonna be like, Eve Plum was there, and you pull the one from the Variety Show out.
Yes.
Who the hell? No one knows her from shit.
And remember, she had to make believe that she was part of the series.
Yeah, yeah. Like
we weren't gonna notice.
That could be.
This might be a little too inside, but it's worth talking about.
Could be one of the worst shows ever put on television was the Brady Bunch Variety Show.
And,
really?
And Eve Plum was a holdout, so they got this this new Jan Brady to do everything, and then they had she was making they believe that she was the real Jan Brady.
They would do sketches on the show, on this variety show, in between their singing and dancing numbers and their guests
with
that would come
on. Their bell bottoms.
Yeah. They would do these sketches where they were the Brady family and do little, like, 5 or 10, 8 minute sketches as if they were on the show still. So the mother would be like, Jan, Jan. And this girl would come in. It's like, that's not Jan. That stinks.
You could always tell if the father or her walked in because because someone would go, hello, faggot, or who are you?
Is it true that Charlie Callis was part of the...
He was the new Peter Brady.
Yes.
Peter.
We have audio of him?
Of him doing dumb sounds.
What, Charlie Callis? We're getting some Charlie Callis.
I got some Charlie Callis. Oh, look, he's doing a make-believe phone bit. Oh,
can we
God,
pop that
this
up?
Is horrible.
Oh, we can do it now.
This has got to be terrible.
Opie.
Oh, I'm way over here.
Opie.
Ralph! Hey, Ralph! Guess who this is? Yes, I mean, this is me, this is y'all. This is y'all, friend, yeah. This is, you know what shorts for? This is Sam. Say, listen there, Sam.
He's laughing at his own joke
today's
now.
Today's my birthday. And for my birthday, my friends, they all hipped in. And you know what they...
Whoa.
And you know what they...
Whoa.
And you know what they bought me? That's right, they bought me...
Knife.
They bought me... Knife. You know, it's a Winchester cut. You put it... Well, right.
There's a shotgun.
So, listen, why don't you jump on your car and drive up to my... Drive over to my house.
Just Jerry Lewis laughing his ass off in the background.
I'm going to go shoot it. Shoot what? What do I know? April, May, this is a great time of year to go out and shoot some meat. You know those animals with the feet that look something like a moose in Hawaii? We'll shoot some birds. So his friend at the other end says...
Horrible. What is he doing? Wow. Who's clapping?
That wasn't bad.
And this is half over, by the way.
It's still...
Yeah, believe me, it'll go on and on, much to the torture of everybody.
Out into the country. Birds flying all around. Thousands of them. So anyhow, the guys who... Let me do that over again. The guy whose birthday it is, he says, hey, look.
Why is he doing
it? My birthday and Mike. I'm gonna just not hear your way. Because I'm gonna fire first.
I don't get it.
He's saying things weird.
Yeah. And then he walks around making funny faces and moving his arms around. Like, he does a lot of visual stuff.
Well, he's on television.
He takes his
yeah. yeah. He does seem to be on television.
It's only bad on the radio, Ant.
Oh, my God. It's driving me nuts.
It just goes on and on of him going...
Well, a nice observation coming in. Let's say hi to Nick in Pennsylvania. Nick?
How you doing, boys?
Hey, Nick.
I just got to ask you guys, what is the difference between Charlie Callis and Twitchell doing the news?
You know something? You're absolutely right, and that's why I hate Louis Twitchell Santani, is because maybe he reminds me of Charlie Callis.
Charlie Callis was doing that on The Tonight Show, though, right?
Was that The Tonight Show?
It's I see Jerry Lewis there, so I don't know.
Was Jerry Lewis
filming it? It was the
in?
Jerry Langford Show.
Yeah.
With special guest, Charlie Callis. And the new comedy find of the century, Rupert Pupkin.
I don't hate Charlie Callis.
I hate him.
We hate him, Jimmy.
That's just not my thing, that wacky, you know, but... Whatever.
Not your thing. I'd rather fuck a male real doll.
No, I can't do both.
Without the doll.
Sam, sounds like this chiller convention sucked.
No, it was a place to see and be seen.
Yeah.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah, Frank Stallone was there.
Not the place to hear and be heard if you're Lou Ferrigno. Only half.
Yeah, why couldn't anyone hear Lou? We're not all deaf.
I'm just going to Charlie Callis my way out of bombs today.
So he said,
I can't hear.
We heard you, Sam. You don't have to say it again.
Yeah.
The reaction you got is the reaction you should have got
by
saying that Frank Stallone was there.
Frank Stallone.
It leads to the big Iron Sheik interview you did.
Yeah, the Iron Sheik was there with his pal Nikolai Volkoff.
Wow.
The Nikolai.
Yeah.
I remember him growing up.
I got him to sign my chair.
Some old school wrestling.
Yeah. The axis of evil, pretty much, as far as wrestling went.
Well, it was a pretty good tag team scene there because Nikolai Volkoff and the Iron Sheik was there, as was Demolition.
Wow.
So, I mean, that's why I went. To meet some of my heroes.
When did you realize it was a waste of time?
It wasn't. I got an Iron Sheik interview.
And that you should have done something nice with your lovely girlfriend instead of doing the nerd thing.
She went. She got to take the pictures.
Yeah, I know she went.
Oh, wow.
She's dedicated to you. She hated being there.
She got to see Tony Curtis.
Chekhov was there from Star Trek?
Yeah.
All right, now we're talking some big stars.
The guy who was in the bunny suit in Donnie Darko was there. Remember that guy?
Are you kidding me?
I'm not kidding.
Remember that guy? It was pretty much the basis of the whole movie.
Yeah, but how do you know it was that guy? How do you know?
He took that bunny hat off a few points in that movie.
The wacky neighbor from Three's Company was there?
He was there.
Is that Larry Klein?
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah.
Pat Harrington himself? Schneider from One Day at a Time?
The guy who played Lurch in the Addams Family movie was there?
Movie?
Oh, okay. I was going to say... I think Lurch is long gone.
Mm-hmm.
And
Eddie Trunk was there signing.
Famous
radio celebrity Eddie Trunk was signing.
Line?
He had more of a line than Frank Stallone did.
My buddy Danny, who was...
Pamela Ferdin?
I'm not kidding. She was there, too.
Pamela Ferdin was the voice of Lucy from Peanuts cartoons, but the later ones.
Oh.
And she was also a child actress that was in... She played, I believe, Felix Unger's daughter in The Odd Couple. And she had that annoying voice, and she was in everything in the 70s.
She was there.
Yeah? How's she looking?
Great.
Yeah, I bet.
The original the original Lois Lane was there signing.
No way! She's not dead?
No, but she appears to be.
How old is she?
She appears to be.
She has to be pushing 90.
Yeah, she does. And she looks every bit. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
She had a sequin jacket on.
Damn.
Would you?
A sequin jacket?
Sam, I mean, would you?
It's Lois Lane.
Yeah, you have to. Sure, of course. I'm with you.
How do I know a lot of these people? Now I'm like starstruck.
See, you should have
so
come.
I'm so kidding.
Why? Oh.
Yeah, because I don't really mean it. I mean, I've seen these people on TV, but as far as them being stars, wow. And then you get to the bottom of the page, and it really gets grim.
The voice of Erin Esurance from the Esurance commercials was there.
What is that?
Stop it.
Yes.
She's a friend of mine. I didn't know she was here.
Who?
Tiffany, the Playboy girl.
Oh.
Oh, yes.
This is Sam talking to the Iron Sheik.
Yeah, let's hear some of that.
All right.
That's Prabhu Anthony.
Opie and Anthony. You remember them?
Yeah.
Yeah, you remember. All right, we're here with the Iron Sheik at Chiller Theater. Iron Sheik, what's the haps?
Absolutely, I'm happy to be in the Chiller Theater. And especially I have Laura, Howard the Store, and Anthony, and Opie. And they are the my real radio station people, and I don't have to talk about myself. Everybody know I'm the legend. I'm the Hall of Fame, made it to the Hall of Fame 2005. And then I'll be very happy to meet my good friend, Mr. John and Nicola. We'll be here. Everything good so far.
It sounds like Tippy Tom.
Yes.
All Who's right. with me? A rush. Of Russian, well,
Iranian.
Iranian, yes. Iranian Tippy Tom.
This is now turning into what I like to call the Buddy Ebsen syndrome. This is the Buddy Ebsen syndrome, where you listen to an earlier tape of the Iron Sheik.
Well, we could do just that.
And then listen to the Iron Sheik now and realize he'll be dead soon.
Let's get it. Let's get the last Iron Sheik interview. Yes. We can do it this time.
Well, here we go.
I like how he said Anthony, and then he goes, Opiun. Because we kept telling him it's Opie and Anthony, and he thought it was Opiun Anthony.
First he called it the Howard Stern and Anthony.
Yes.
And really?
Yeah.
It's hilarious.
Yeah, Howard Stern and Anthony.
And then, and Opiun. Because he thinks it's Opiun Anthony. Yeah. And he always has. So your name is always going to be Opiun with him. He's a retard.
This is him from about, I don't know, 6-7 years ago at NEW.
Right, let's hear him.
Basically, it's whatever you want to say. Whatever you want to say. As long as your name and Opie and Anthony is in it.
Right.
Whatever you want to say.
Okay.
Yeah, just do it.
You tell me when I go. This is Iron Sheik, the World Wrestling Federation champion. Pleasure for me to the Anthony and Opie, and pleasure to I come here. I want to say hello to all my wrestling fans, and hello to all people, to the wrestling, and pleasure to I be here.
What? And the Opie?
Keep that in mind. So that's like 7 years ago, and this is a mere couple days ago.
Yes.
All right.
That's Prabhu Anthony.
Opie and Anthony. You remember them?
Yeah.
Yeah, you remember. All right, we're here with the Iron Sheik at Chiller Theater. Iron Sheik, what's the haps?
Absolutely, I'm happy to be in the Chiller Theater. And especially, I have Laura, Howard the Store, and Anthony, and Opie. And they are my real radio station people. And I don't have to talk about myself. Everybody know I'm the legend. I'm the Hall of Fame, made it to the Hall of Fame 2005. And then I'll be very happy to meet my good friend, Mr. John and Nicola. We'll be here. Everything good so far.
It's Tippy. It's Tippy Turban. Stephen S. from Bayshore. Tippy Turban.
Wow, he doesn't sound too good.
And then you got him to talk a little more here, Sam.
I mean, this is an interview. It's not just, you know.
Yeah, I see.
You got to get him to answer some of the tough questions.
All right.
It's been a while since you've been on with Opie and Anthony. Do you miss the guys?
Absolutely. Opie and Anthony, they are good people. They call me my home in Georgia.
What? I didn't know.
You told me. Him?
Yeah, that you guys call his house in Georgia just to say
did
what's
you?
Up.
Wow.
That's cool, that. Guys. That's awesome.
Well, you know. We do have celebrity friends, and he's one of them.
Do you have a fear that someday he's going to walk off and not be your friend anymore, Opie? You're going to screw something up.
Say something stupid.
The Iron Sheik says we call him.
Can I have his home number? I'd love to call the Iron Sheik.
Wow.
It's been a while since you've been on with Opie and Anthony. Do you miss the guys?
Absolutely. Opie and Anthony, they are good people. They call me my home in Georgia. First of all, I talk to them, and I'm very, very happy to actually talk about them. If you saw them, please say hello for me.
Is there anything? Is there anybody out there that you want to threaten right now? Anybody you want to tell them what you're going to do to them?
Well, absolutely. Like I said, Anthony and Opion and
Opion.
Anthony, they are good friends, and God bless him, and I'm very happy to be here.
Thanks a lot.
God bless you, and have a good day.
You asked him if he wanted to threaten anybody,
I think,
and he said Anthony and Opion.
I listened to it a couple of times, and I think he was spending so long trying to figure out how to say Opie's name that he forgot the question, so then he just kept talking about how much he liked you guys.
Opion.
Yes.
Holy... Wow.
God damn.
That old age is a bitch.
It certainly is.
How old is he?
I think he was always like that, though.
Well, yeah, but I mean...
I've heard rumors about him, Sam.
His mind's deteriorated.
You've heard the rumor, right?
Something has deteriorated his mind.
It might be a little...
Yeah. He's cracking up?
Yeah, yeah, there's rumors of illicit substances.
There's a little crack that makes the rounds every once in a while.
Corbin Burnson was there.
Yeah, he was.
Corbin Burnson.
Everybody... From the movie Basketball?
Yes. I just think of him from the Seinfeld episode where George talks the ear off Corbin Burnson.
The greatest project he ever did was The Dentist.
Yes, The Dentist was really good.
He was on The Celebrity Mole.
Yeah.
You guys like The Celebrity Mole.
Well, what was the big show? L.A. Law. That was his big show.
I know him from Celebrity Mole.
All right.
Different generations there, Sam.
I'm stunned. That's funny. And then stomp your foot and get the word out. Kick his brittle bones. Wait a minute. Is that the little kid from... What? Oh, Uncle Paul. Poltergeist?
Yeah.
Which one? She died.
No, not the dead one, which would be great to just card out at these conventions.
And yell at her.
Dress her up like JonBenet. the kid that the boy that got taken by the tree.
How old is
he now? How old is that kid now?
I don't know. Yeah, he's an adult.
Does he look just as goofy, only in adult fashion? That's always funny to see.
Yeah,
it's like, hey, you got the goofy kid face still, but it's got whiskers.
Well, the problem
is gray hair.
All those child actors like come to these with like Ed Hardy T-shirts and really well groomed facial hair and like. Dyed hair, so you know they're still in Hollywood trying to make it
out
there.
I got my second coming. I know it. Tarantino will bring me back. He brought Travolta back. Larry Storch from F Troop.
He was wearing the hat, too.
He was wearing the Larry Storch F Troop hat.
And the kerchief.
And the kerchief.
Mm-hmm.
How bad is that when you're in the room alone at some point and putting that hat on from the mirror and realizing the show was made in 1965 and like you're putting that kerchief and hat on and straightening it out and looking in the mirror going, I'm ready. It's showtime.
And every year.
It's showtime.
And every year, less people care.
Yeah, less and less people care.
Less and less. Maybe in 75, it was still like.
Yeah, it's like, hey, Larry Storch from F Troop.
Now it's 2009.
Oh, they don't even play reruns of F Troop anymore, I don't think. Meadowlark Lemon?
That's a good one. He's a legend.
The Meadowlark, or was it a fake one?
No, it was him. I arrived at his table, and he was not at the table.
Oh, what was he doing?
I mean, I guess having a lunch break. I don't know.
Was he signing basketballs? I'd get a ball signed.
Yeah, he signed whatever.
Where is he?
Right there.
Right there.
Right there? Which one is him?
He's the like guy. He's with the yellow background.
He's probably the most famous Globetrotter ever.
Oh, yeah.
Amanda Plummer.
She's been to a lot of those conventions.
From Pulp Fiction?
Yep, she's doing the convention circuit.
Wow. That's a get.
She's kind of sexy.
And Worf.
Worf?
Worf was there.
Michael Dorn himself?
The London brothers, Jeremy and Jason, were there.
Who?
Well, Jeremy London was in Mallrats, and he was checking out my girlfriend.
Oh, I gotcha.
Which Jess pointed out to me.
Oh, I see that. Right. Yes, okay. I know who that is, of course.
That's the move. She wants you to,
What, to defend myself against Jeremy London? What's he done?
but he, that's probably what she wants.
What?
Like, to see that you care enough to,
right,
you know, throw some fists with some.
I'll knock out Jeremy London.
Yeah, do some battle with the guy.
I will. I'll fight Jeremy London
the
today.
The black guy from Land of the Giants.
He was there.
What?
The whole cast of Land from the Giants.
What?
That's one of the fun things, that sometimes they put together little reunions.
Do they?
Yeah, and you can go and get one item signed by everyone or individual items signed.
That's a guy I would like to have met or seen again. Tom Noonan. In the right, he was in a play. He played George, or Lenny.
Oh, I know
in,
that.
In the play in New Brunswick, New Jersey, my grandmother took me to see of Mice and Men.
Yeah.
He was Lenny, and I got an autograph.
You did.
And then he turned out to be, he was one of Rodney and Pesci's friends in what was the fucking Easy Money?
Yeah, yeah. I've seen that guy. I know who that is.
Did you guys watch Confessions of a Teen Idol? When they were going to rebuild all their careers on VH1?
Oh, no. Yeah. I actually watched that show.
Yeah. Chris Atkins from the show, who was going to rebuild his career, and he was the one guy they said could be an A-lister.
Yeah, yeah. Wow.
He was at Chiller Theater.
No way.
Yeah.
You're kidding.
From the Blue Lagoon.
Yes, he was in the Blue Lagoon. Remember that?
He was supposed to be a big star again because of that show.
I know, and now he's selling all kinds of autographs and stuff. It's great.
Oh, Scott the guy from took care of him, huh?
The guy, yeah, from Gremlins?
Yes.
The kid from Gremlins?
And Waxwork 1 and 2.
And Waxwork, right, right. Yeah, Waxwork, yeah. 1 and 2.
Dude, I love these fucking conventions.
The best.
They are the best.
You know why? You are an autograph whore.
But it's fun just to see, like I told you, I got Joyce DeWitt.
It is kind of fun to see these people. I would like, because first of all, I'm looking at the pictures that they have on this website with their names.
Yeah.
These are all old, old publicity shots of these people.
Well, that's the beauty of it. These are the pictures that you can get. You can get. These are the ones you get signed.
Yeah.
Like you get the, and then you take a picture with them, and then you can compare. They don't look anything.
Oh. Don't you have to pay for every picture?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You have to pay per picture and
per autograph. So you have to be
autograph.
Very selective of which, yes, big star you,
wow,
want a picture with.
This could run into thousands.
I went, yeah, easy.
Last year, a few years actually back, I went to, there's another one of these in I think Cherry Hill called Monster Mania. And it was the big They Live reunion with
no way,
Rowdy Roddy Piper and Keith David. And they were both selling the exact same 8x10 photo. So I picked up the 8x10 at one person's table. I paid for the photo and the autograph. It was like $50. Then the other table for Keith David or whatever, there was a thing that said, you know, if you bring your own item, it's an additional fee. They were charging me the additional fee because I bought the same 8x10 that he was selling at the other guy's table. And they said, well, you brought your own item.
No, but yeah, it's like you don't want five different pictures of different people signed.
It cost me like $100.
Oh, shit.
These two idiots to sign up one 8x10.
That's it. Like they had at one of these things, a Texas Chainsaw Massacre reunion. And I was like, oh, I should get a poster signed by everyone. Except it's $20, not per item. It's per signature.
Yeah.
So you have to, it costs,
crazy.
You have to pay $100 for this poster that you're going to get signed, and then there's like seven people there, so it's $20 per signature.
That's crazy.
It costs you a couple $100.
Easy.
I went nuts when I was there. I didn't mind. You know who didn't want my money? Joni from Happy Days.
Yeah. Money's no good.
Turns out
here.
She's a fan or
yeah,
something.
Yeah, she was a Lucky Louie fan. She's like, can me and my husband get a picture with you?
Wow.
I gave her the money for the picture anyway because, you know, they're not working.
First
a lot of
all,
because it's obvious.
Nuttier than
it.
A shithouse rat, that woman.
Still sexy, though.
No.
No,
yes.
Stop. She was never sexy.
Was.
Oh, my God.
Joni was never
shortcake?
Sexy.
Shortcake?
No.
No.
E, shortcake. E.
Can we?
Never really sexy.
Can we play the Iron Sheik ID from the NEW days to wrap up the chiller thing?
Oh, please.
All right, this is the famous Iron
Love
Sheik
it.
ID for the show.
Iron Sheik.
What do you want? We'll try a short one. We'll try a long one.
Okay, so you just tell me anything, especially when I saw, just talk
as
about myself.
As long as your name and Opie and Anthony is in it?
Right. Perfect.
Have fun.
All right.
Do whatever you want to do.
All right.
All right?
Yes. This is Iron Sheik, World Wrestling Federation, 3-time champion, All-American AAU champion. Pleasure for me to the Anthony and Opium. Bring me here to New York to I say hello to the, all my wrestling fans. And everybody know I'm the real Middle Eastern man, come to the greatest wrestling country and most famous city in the world, Manhattan, Madison Square Garden. I
come three times champion. I want to say hello to the, all my wrestling fans, especially all American and also my Iranian friend. خدمت همه شنوندگان ایرانی عزیز سلام عرض میکنم. همه دنیا آرون شیخ خسرو وزیری رو میشناسن. Pleasure for me to I come back here again one more time to I talk to the Opion and Anthony, and pleasure for me always.
Good,
very good.
I don't want to get you guys too excited because I know you got the rest of the show to concentrate on.
Yes.
But there might be a certain former professional wrestler that's very interested in making a return to the Opie and Anthony show.
Wow.
After some schmoozing I did at Chiller Theater.
Is it the Iron Sheik?
Yes, it's the Iron Sheik.
You asshole.
Shouldn't we just be calling him? We got his home number.
Yeah, we call him all the time down in Georgia.
Just call him
apparently.
In Georgia.
We could have called him today.
Was he wearing the curly shoes?
No, Iron Sheik has bad knees, so
he does.
The Sheik doesn't stand up too often at these appearances.
Yeah,
but he did have his his head thing on.
Oh, he had his head piece on that that's something.
And his Hall of Fame ring that he was quick to show me.
He could still call himself the Iron Sheik, huh? Why is that?
Because he'll break your back if you tell him he can't.
But what if, like, Vince, he's not with the WWE or anything.
No, that was before Vince turned into a complete asshole.
Hey!
There was a time he allowed these guys to keep their names.
He's taking your name. Your name's mine now, Iron Sheik.
And then he has to change it to what? Like, Bronze.
Yeah.
You know,
the Bronze Shaw.
Yeah, something. So he can continue trying to make a living.
Iron Sheik, I can't use anymore. The pleasure for me.
That's always sad. You see one of these guys at an independent wrestling show and they're
titanium towel head.
They're reworking their name so they can make a couple hundred bucks on a Saturday.
Yeah. They would have changed the Iron Sheik's name to the Sheik from Iran. That would have been the Iron Sheik's name, because that's exactly what they do.
Let's go to the phones. There's a couple of really good stories about past Chiller conventions. So,
hello, Opie and Anthony's show.
Hey, Tim.
How you doing now?
What do you got?
I went to a sci-fi convention. It was called the Super Mega Fest.
Yeah.
And Adam West was there doing autographs for the 1960s Batman show. And I went in with a friend of mine. We had a photo of him as the mayor from Family Guy. And I asked him to sign it to Tim from Mayor Adam West, the man who loves his taffy. And he looked at me like I had 10 heads. And I turned to the guy next to him who was collecting the money and said, will you just take care of these two? And he said, what are you, kids from college or something? He just acted all pissed and annoyed. And that was a big
He is pissed and annoyed.
Yeah, doesn't Adam West understand he's more people know him from Family Guy than the original Batman TV series?
I don't understand.
At this point?
If you're going to use your own voice, then why not? Like, do you not even get your own jokes?
Yeah.
So.
Very good. Thank you, sir.
My God, the celebrities that were there. Mm-hmm. The voice of Charlie Brown from 83 to 85.
Yeah.
That is probably the worst years for the Charlie Brown franchise.
Those were the lean peanuts. Years.
Yeah, the lean years.
Those were the chemo years. I don't even know what that means, but what the fuck. Let's take another phone call here.
Hello, Opie and Anthony show.
All right, listen. I guess I got to bring everyone into the bit.
Yeah, you got to bring them up to speed on this one.
We have Ira from the Jay Thomas Show that was in Friday. He said this probably 1,000 times.
Hello, Opie and Anthony Show.
So that's how we're going to go to the phones for a while. So when you hear that, it's time to talk. Chris.
Oh, sorry, man.
Yeah.
Yes, you are.
Go ahead, Chris.
All right, I got a good story about Val Kilmer, who was at last year's Chiller.
Yeah.
All right, well, me and a few friends were staying on the top floor, and we weren't aware that we were staying across the hallway from them. We heard screaming and yelling from across the hallway, and next thing you know, we see a chick running out naked and Val Kilmer chasing after her, and she all of a sudden screamed, you got a fucking small cock, and all of a sudden people on the floor were just like staring at Val Kilmer butt-ass naked on the floor.
We're supposed to believe this went down?
I don't believe that.
And TMZ or nobody picked up on this?
No one would have said anything.
What are you trying to do today?
Just stop.
What are you doing?
My goodness.
Chris.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I work at the... Dude.
Val Kilmer's a pretty big name, so if some girl was running naked out of a convention where a lot of people could see this.
Not even one cell phone picture in this age of technology?
Saying, Val, you got a small cock. I think it would be on some of these Hollywood blog sites.
Well, the thing is, this is on the top floor of the hotel where all the staff and the celebrities stay.
Mm-hmm. And you were there and you saw it.
Yes.
Yeah, of course.
All right.
Urban
That's
legend.
That's what Chris is saying. Thank you, Chris.
No problem.
All right. Hey, Sam, why don't we move into the other thing that you got for us today?
Oh, okay.
While you're here, let's get this out of the way.
Let's get all the Sam stuff out of the way.
Well,
our old
radio station that gave us the boot so they could play a lot of pop music.
Yeah. Right.
Remember 92.3 Now it's now called?
Yeah, and commercials, too.
They're finally doing commercials?
Yeah. Oh. Their 10,000 songs ended, so they got some sweet commercials 10, on,
10,000 commercials now.
Really? How's the 92.3 Now working out? Well, I swear to you, not a buzz. I went to the Devils playoff game, by the way.
Yeah.
Thank you to Kevin Smith. It was a fine time. Not many stories to really tell. He's just a stand-up dude and really cool. But I was walking through what was called Radio Row.
Yeah.
And 92.3 Now was there.
Really?
No one gave a shit. Not one person walked up to the van to get info.
I would have grabbed one of those T-shirts quick. I like the logo.
Z100 was there. They had a crowd. The Jersey Rock station. what's the Jersey Rock station? Rad or something?
I don't know, actually.
I always forget. But they had a big crowd.
Jersey.
And 92.3 Now was just sitting there just looking very awkward.
I find that really hard to believe.
Yeah, you got a buzz on this station?
I think there is a pretty solid buzz. You got Chunky. You got Tic Tac. Lisa Page. You know what I'm saying?
Clam up.
Is
Lisa Page hot? I can't tell from the pictures.
She's
all right?
She's all right.
Is she a hot?
So what do we got on 92.3 Now?
Well,
I see you got a song in front of me here.
Yeah, because a lot of these stations like to find like a song that's funny or whatever that's local that relates so that they can call it their own. So this is not a song that Z100 is playing, but it's a song that's tearing up 92.3 Now. And basically, it's called Jersey, Bitch. And it's pretty funny.
By Faux Onassis?
Faux Onassis.
It's pretty funny, huh?
It is, and it talks about being from New Jersey. It's a hip-hop song. It's catchy. It's the type of thing like when you and the boys are like getting ready to go out on a Friday night.
Right,
you want
right.
this banging.
Only 92.3 Now could play it?
Well, only 92.3 Now is playing it.
That means the song sucks?
No.
What are they doing?
It means it's too... Well, because Z100 only plays the old stuff.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Obviously we know he's going to be playing the new stuff now.
All right.
God, is that annoying.
Sounds like Charlie Callis.
Hey. Drink all day. Drink all night.
I like it.
Yeah. I'm in New Jersey, bitch. Drink all day. Drink all night. Bottles be popping. I'm in New Jersey, bitch. Shorty looking at me. She saying, look at that B.
Enough with Shorty.
Enough with Enough Shorty. With
That's how we talk in New Jersey, bitch.
Who is Shorty?
Oh, Shorty is
a girl.
Enough with Shorty.
Sherrod always calls me Shorty. You can be a guy and be Shorty, too.
Oh, no, you can't.
Uh-oh.
That's you're his bitch.
I think he's got something else in mind for you. I hear Shorty's a girl.
Yeah.
Yeah, generally it means you're
Enough with
you're
Shorty.
Woman.
Enough
you're
with
woman.
The, yeah. Enough with the, what is it, the club?
At the club.
Enough with the bub and the
club. The bub and the club.
We're popping bottles in New Jersey right
Are
now.
You?
Yeah.
Are you really?
Yeah.
enough with all that crap. What's some of those
the
other?
The club.
What else they sing about all the time, those songs? You got the bub and the club.
I don't know. There's always like guns and stuff.
Do they do the hoopty still?
No, no.
What do they call their rides these days?
I don't know. Cars.
Paddy wagons.
Whips, yeah, whips. You call it your whip.
Paddy wagon. What year are you living in?
All right, Clancy, get the paddy wagon. Well, they all got rounded up.
You got to stomp your foot.
I can't.
Jimmy
Callis.
You got to stomp your foot, and then you get the right word in, Jimmy.
Yes.
Follow the formula.
Jimmy Callis.
I'm Jimmy Warts.
What do they call their rides? Well,
yeah, you can call it your ride, your whip.
How about we start something new, too, and we pronounce the words in songs?
Well, no, it's
proper pronunciation.
Car and girlfriend.
Yeah, girlfriend.
And firearm.
And champagne.
And champagne.
Right.
And it's nightclub establishment.
What's the big one now? It's not Cristal anymore? Because then one of them have a problem with Cristal, so they said no more Cristal in our song.
Yeah, at one point Jay-Z decided no more Cristal.
Well, Cristal was getting a little angry that their product was being linked to a bad element of society.
Jehovah?
The gangster.
Oh, boy. Sam, a lot of info coming in about this song. Cat in Florida and many others. This song is a ripoff of another song. What? The original was all about Miami.
Well, it's a remix.
See, Miami is like a cool place to sing about. Right. No offense to our Jersey listeners.
Oh,
but,
hell no.
No.
But you can't have that same, like, Miami feel as you sing about Jersey.
It's a remix.
Unless you're Bobo.
I'm in New Jersey, bitch.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there's another one. All right, let's make a list. No more Bub in the Club, no more Shorty, and no more B.
Yeah,
what's
come
up,
on.
B? We'll make a list today.
4-0 with the super hot flow, girls going wild, yeah, that's me. Hey. This is something y'all been wanting. Jersey's here, let's get this jumping. Rutgers girls know how to party.
Rutgers here, let's... No jumping either.
And how can you stop jumping?
Jumping?
And Rutgers girls know how to party?
It's
really?
In Jersey.
It's in Jersey.
Exactly. They don't know how to party at Rutgers. Bunch of lesbians at the woman's school.
They got a huge woman's school there. You're
Douglas
right.
College, I think it is.
I don't know. I think there's sluttier girls somewhere else in Jersey than Rutgers.
You know, bunch of girls who are bunch of girls who are licking pussy. I like being Jimmy Callis. It's fun.
Jimmy Callis. Jimmy Callis. Your new character, Jimmy Callis.
Jimmy Callis.
Hey. This is something y'all been wanting. Jersey's here, let's get this jumping. Rutgers girls know how to party. Rutgers here, let's get it started. Let it bump, turn it up, give me some of that. Take a shot of goose, chilling in the booth. This is how we do here in Jersey. When you out in Jersey, time to wild out, bug out, and get crazy. Finish off the Henny, still it ain't phase me. I'm only here for
any slang for any fucking booze.
Yeah.
No what? Goose, no Henny, no fucking Patron.
Right.
I don't want to hear any fucking booze being referenced in the songs.
Well, how are they supposed to pop bottles in?
Pop bottles? No popping bottles.
Is that what they
I'd
say?
Love to pop yeah, a pop bottle bottles. Over your fucking afro yeah. at this point.
That's a term. It wouldn't break.
That's a term, the pop.
Pop bottles.
Yo, let's go to the club. We be popping bottles.
Popping some bottles.
All right, let's pop some bottles.
Let's get Bobo in immediately to do his New Jersey rap song, and we're going to make it a hit.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to make the Bobo rap song a hit. Drew Boogie, I think, could pull that one off.
Bobo could pop bottles.
Dr. Dre couldn't pull that one off.
The only one that was popping bottles and made it fun was Fatty Arbuckle.
I leave it to Ant to find the one rape murder with a bottle.
He knew how to have some fun.
He's so dead. He knew how to have a lot of fun. He took the bottle. And broke it in a cunt.
You didn't tap your foot. It's the only... Okay. I'm obsessed with the foot part of the bed.
He's too small in his chair.
Yeah,
he can't reach the floor.
He's tiny in his chair.
I'm Jimmy Callis, not Jimmy Lark Lemon.
Finish off the Henny, still it ain't faze me. I'm only here for your entertainment. So, take it off, girl, pop that top. Show the world Jersey girls know how to rock. Hey, from the club off to the grease trucks. From the club off to the grease trucks. Order up two fat bitch, hold the veggies. Catch up for a heavy Jersey. We out in Jersey, bitch. We out in Jersey, bitch. From the garden, time to get retarded. Jersey's here, yeah, now it's a party. Drink all day, drink all night.
Along.
I'm in New Jersey, bitch.
Wow.
I'm in New Jersey, bitch. You don't like that song?
They're
really pushing it on 92.3 now.
I bet they are.
I hear they're also playing an awful anti-Chris Brown song. Do we have that one yet?
Oh, I haven't heard that, but I'd love
you're not
to.
On top of what's now.
I try to say as now as possible.
How many of these do you think there are?
Could you play the New Jersey, the not New Jersey, the bitch song, please? I love that song.
Yeah, we're going to get that right on right now for ya.
It's true. Their talk breaks are now, they play that song, and then they get texts and phone calls as to, did you like it?
Shut up.
Ah, and smash then, or trash?
And then 15 minutes later, they go, well, we're talking about the I'm in New Jersey song, and if you didn't hear it, here it is.
Oh.
And so that way everybody's included.
How many Twitter friends do they have?
I don't know.
They're up to a couple hundred, I think. I mean, they're doing well, yeah. We got kicked out the door for this horse shit.
That's it.
We wouldn't play this song, though. That's true.
Oh, we.
Yeah, if,
we
maybe if we
wouldn't.
Played this, yeah. we'd fit in with those guys.
Popping bottles.
Drink all day, drink all night. Bottles we popping. I'm in New Jersey, bitch.
Yeah, baby. Where my Jersey ladies?
Hey!
Where my Jersey ladies? Phone on the mic, man, I get them right. Out here, many flavors, different types. They're short ones, tall ones, skinny girls. Ow! Big girls, love them by the pound. Anyhow, anywhere, any town. These Jersey girls, man, they all get down. So, get down, get down. Drop that booty low. Drop that booty low. Low, low.
In other words, we don't need to hear anymore is booty.
Booty is the oldest fucking
drop,
rap word. Ass. Whatever. Booty.
They have.
It's so passe.
Booty was hip for a while, but let's stop now. Let's bring it back to
booty.
Ass.
Booty.
That
booty.
Twitter friends 92.3 now has. It's like, ha ha ha. It's like, ha ha ha. It's like 174 fucking friends.
That's it, huh?
That stinks.
Oh, they suck.
Wow, that's fun. Really bad.
Yeah. All right.
Get down, drop that booty low, drop that booty low, 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 real low, low. Shorty got a mask, so we keep it down low. I'm a maniac, tell him where the ladies at. Shorty gave me good hair, how to call a brainiac. Where we at? Jersey, where we at? Jersey, ha, the guard is stay. Oh, now they heard me. Drink all day, drink all night.
But that's drinking bottles all the time.
Where are we?
I'm in New Jersey, bitch.
Oh, drink all day, yeah.
Drink all night, bottles we popping. I'm in New Jersey, bitch. It's four Nasses, bitch. And we in New Jersey, bitch. We just having fun over here. Oh.
Just having some fun.
How about stink all day, stink all night. I'm in New Jersey, bitch. Place does reek. Oh, wow. Yes. Okay, hold on. That's Jimmy.
We got more info on this song coming in.
Hello, Opie and Anthony show.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, man.
Hey, Andrew.
Hey, just so you know, that shitty top 40 station out in Chicago is playing that Jersey song, too, except they replaced Jersey with Chicago.
Are there really other versions all over of whatever state?
This is the near? New, this is the new We Built This City song.
Yeah, where the traffic report in the middle
was from.
Yeah, for
all you old school radio guys.
Yeah, but none of them are as good as a Jersey song.
I wonder if they did a bunch of versions for big cities.
I just wonder why they didn't pick New York, because the station's based in New York.
Yeah.
Why New Jersey, bitch?
Syllables.
No, I'm in New York, bitch. It works just as well as Chicago, bitch. Schenectady is a big one.
Schenectady would be good.
Ronkonkoma is good.
I'm in Ronkonkoma, bitch. Shoehorn that fucking city in there.
Utah works. Bethesda. You know, Kissimmee.
Oh, God.
Can't we make our own version of this song somehow? With David or Bobo. Or...
I'm in Modesto, bitch. Glub all day. Glub all night.
Anything else?
Funny.
Sam is Sam's in touch with pop culture. Anything else, Sam?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, that's kind of what's going on right now. The Iron Sheik and I'm in New Jersey, bitch.
That's it.
Yeah. Sam knows what to bring to the table.
Sure does.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right.
Okay.
Oof. Madonna got hurt. I saw a video of Madonna getting injured in Seattle.
Oh, yeah.
Kenny was hinting to that. Yeah, that's how she actually got hurt.
The horse injury with Madonna. You thought maybe she was reinventing herself again and trying to get some press.
Yeah, I hope his knees buckled. It's cock just fucking bashed her brains in. I hope she was banging the horse and his fucking knees buckled. Way to spell it out, Jim. We got it. I hope she was...
On the way, we got Mayor Bloomberg yelling at a guy in a wheelchair. That's some good audio.
What's wrong with Mayor Bloomberg?
And young girls find four people having sex in a Taco Bell bathroom. Another fast food story for everybody.
A lot of people screwing in the fast food places.
Why?
You know? I don't know. Is that all about?
Is that a trend? We're going to find out next.
Yes.
You're checking out the Opie and Anthony Show. I think we're going to talk to Dana White in a few minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Our pal Chuck Liddell got knocked out, what, first round? I didn't even see the fight.
He got knocked the fuck out. It was like 4 minutes or something in.
He got knocked out, and they're saying that might be it for Chuck Liddell. I doubt it.
Really?
I know a lot of people are saying it, but...
Dude, they've been saying it for a while now, though.
It's kind of tough to leave the fight game. I don't think it's over for Chuck Liddell.
I was watching the knockout, knockdown.
He didn't look good, but no. I bet you he tries one more.
Yeah, but
one more.
I don't know if Dana will let him. I mean, those guys are friends, and it's like you're watching somebody you like really put themselves in danger.
Yeah, he's kind of fucking himself up.
It seemed like his
pounded in the face like that.
It seemed like his skills dropped in the last, 18 months?
Yeah, I think
he had a big drop-off, no? I know he's an older guy and had an amazing career, but...
I think that's it. It's an older guy, and other people are getting better. You know, younger guys coming up. How long has UFC been really popular? I mean, 5, 6 years?
Yeah.
Chuck's
been around
39.
A lot longer, but yeah, popular for 5 or 6, yeah.
You know, he wasn't a 20-year-old guy when he hit. You know, he was, 33 years old.
That's got to be frustrating for someone like Chuck Liddell. You know you got the skills. You know you're probably one of the baddest fighters ever. But you didn't get to fight in your prime because the sport comes into its own the last 5 years of your career.
Yeah,
that's
going to
be really frustrating, and that's why I think he might fight again. Like, he's got that in the back of his brain. Like, I don't want to go out this way. Here's audio of the fight Saturday.
Under a minute remains in round one. Liddell might be trying to set up an uppercut. That right shoulder dropped for a second. Liddell is down! Shogun trying to finish! And it is all!
And it's what?
And it is
and
all.
It's, and it's what? It's what?
And it is all.
Why did that
Chuck's
end?
Back up.
I don't know.
No.
What's that?
I don't know. We know that's where it ended, but how about we go right to the end there?
The video got yanked off of all the file sharing sites, and that's the only copy we could find.
As you were recording? Oh, okay. Okay.
With that, we got Dana White on the phone. Dana.
Good morning.
Hey, how are you, Dana?
What's up, man?
The owner of the UFC, of course. Yeah, pretty good. We were just talking about Chuck Liddell, and a lot of people, including yourself, saying that's pretty much his last fight, but I just don't see it that way. I see Chuck wanting to maybe go out on his own terms and maybe he fights one more.
Now, he went out on his own terms. You know, I wanted him to retire after the Rashad Evans fight.
Yeah.
He flew out to Vegas, talked to me, and said, I want one more. Let me take another run at the title. And he said, I'm going to train hard for this thing. I'm going to change up my training. I'm going to, I'm going to stay out of the nightclubs, et cetera, et cetera. And he came out and did it on his own terms. He went out the way he wanted to, you know, in a slugfest. Chuck Liddell style, you know, it was I think it was a great last fight. Trust me when I tell you, that's his last fight.
Well, yeah, a lot of people are, there's a lot of speculation as to what happened. Is it purely age, because it's a relatively short period of time that he went from just being that ring monster to, you're watching the fights and going, wow, he just doesn't seem to have it anymore.
Yeah, he's going to be 40 years old, man. What happened is we all turned 40, and in the fight business, it's never too subtle. You know, mm-hmm. When it hits you fast. And Chuck Liddell is a guy who he helped us build this business. He helped us build the sport. He's what more does this guy have to prove? He was a world champion. He's the most famous mixed martial artist on the world, and he's made a lot of money. He's he has nothing left to prove.
And people know that what's happening is simply age. I mean, it does happen to every fighter. Unfortunately for Chuck, by the time that he got really, really famous and well-known, he must have, how long has UFC been really big? I mean, 6 years maybe? I mean, maybe seven?
Yeah, he's been a huge star since, 2005 to the mainstream. But, to a mixed martial arts fan, he's been a huge star for, 10 years, 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and even that, the guy had him by 12 years, this guy. That's a huge difference with two guys fighting. And I think the difference between you guys in boxing is I like the fact that you're saying, that's it, man. He had an amazing run, and it's time for him to step aside, not get hurt or make himself look bad, as opposed to boxing promoters, those fucking vultures. You're 60 years old, they want to cart you out for one more fight.
Well, we had Don King on the show recently there. Dana.
What does a guy like Chuck do after the fight game?
You know what, man? He's been good to us. He's one of my best friends. He's still gonna be a part of the UFC. He's not
going
anywhere. you know, I'll keep him busy.
That's good to see, because he's a fun guy to have around, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm. He is. He's a great guy. He's been incredibly loyal to us, and like I said, he helped us build this business. He helped us build this sport, and he's going to continue to do that. He'll stay with the organization, and he's going to do just fine. Trust me. Don't worry about Chuck Liddell fans. He's going to do just fine.
Is Rampage going to fight Rashad Evans?
Yes. First Lyoto Machida is going to fight Rashad Evans, and then Rampage will fight the winner.
Okay. Because somebody said that he sounded like, when they asked him after his last fight, he really wasn't too keen on fighting Rashad Evans. Was it just because he just fought, or does Evans, you think, have his number?
Yeah, no. He wants to fight. Believe me, he wants to fight Rashad Evans. They don't like each other at all.
Oh, really?
And, he couldn't fight because before the Wanderlei Silva fight, when he was training for that fight, he tore something in his jaw. He tore a ligament or a muscle. Like, I can't remember exactly what it was. And he fought with that. Then he went right back into training and fought again with that same injury. Then got it fixed after the last fight.
Oh, okay. Well, you actually came out, too, which was, again, really rare to see somebody do this. You came out and apologized after, the next day or at the press conference, about the Anderson Silva.
Anderson Silva.
What did you feel was happening there?
Listen, I thought we put on a great card that night. It was a great night of fights, but obviously the main event for the title was Anderson Silva. Anderson Silva has been on this tear for 2 years. I mean, destroying people. And ever since Chicago, I don't know what the hell happened to this guy. You know, fighting very defensive, not offensive. Literally, I shouldn't even say that. Those last two times of fighting, he's not even throwing punches. It's like he's just, and the fight goes the distance. The only reason the fight didn't go the distance in Chicago was because of the Cote's knee blew out. So I just, you know, that's not what people pay to see.
No, that's not what it's about. No.
You don't like when fights go the distance?
It's not that fights go the distance every night. There was the whole undercard that night went the distance. I didn't apologize for any of those fights. Mm-hmm. I apologize for fights when people buy fights and guys don't fight.
Let me ask you, though, if a guy is fighting, and maybe for whatever reason he's switched strategies, or do you think that he's just not trying hard enough? Because it's almost like when two guys are fighting, they're not thinking about putting on a good show. They're thinking about actually winning the fight. But do you think it's more than that with him?
Yeah, I do. Listen, I've seen this guy fight for years. You know, I'm trying to wrap my brain around what's wrong with him right now. I can't figure this out. And to be honest with you, I think part of the problem is this guy's so dominant and so good. He really is that talented. I just don't know if he – so I'm thinking about having to move up to 205. Believe me, he'll be challenged at 205 pounds. It's the most stacked division in mixed martial arts. You know, let's see how he does with some of these guys.
So what do you think? He's not challenged?
Jack DeForest Griffin. You got Thiago Silva. You've got Lyoto Machida, Rashad Evans. I mean, the list goes on and on. Jardine, I could go on all day with that division.
Do you think he's just not challenged and he's trying to win in a different way? Like almost like not put his best stuff out and still win?
I honestly couldn't even tell you. I don't even know. I can tell you this. He's going to fight at 205 next, and we're going to find out what's up.
When people – well, I don't know if this – I don't know if you even know this, but when people bet on the fight – Is he such a heavy a favorite that it's hard to get people to bet against him?
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know about that. I don't even know what the line was for that fight. You know, I'm sure he was a big favorite though.
Yeah. You know, if all of a sudden you look human, and I'm not saying that he would do that, but it's just been speculated that if all of a sudden you look human, people are more likely to think that, hey, this guy could possibly lose, and it's a little easier to get that action going.
I don't think anybody who's seen any fights of Anderson's think he looks like he's going to lose anytime soon. Mm. You know, he had absolutely no shot of losing that night. He was completely dominant while not even fighting. You know what I mean?
Right.
He's that good.
Oh, we had Kurt Angle on.
Yeah.
And what was he saying, Jimmy?
He wasn't. He didn't badmouth anybody at UFC. He said he had great respect for the UFC fighters.
I think he's saying that he's definitely going to be fighting.
Yeah, he kind of alluded to it.
Hmm.
Any comment?
Yeah. I like Kurt. He's a great guy. I have a good relationship with Kurt Angle.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
He's a good guy. I don't know. I don't think you're going to see Kurt fighting in the UFC anytime soon.
Do you think he just
couldn't? Brock Lesnar made that transition. It's very, very, very rare for a guy to make a transition from professional wrestling to mixed martial arts.
Yeah.
When is him and Frank Mir fighting?
They're fighting on UFC 100 in July in Las Vegas.
Okay. And
UFC 100 never even went on public sale and never even made it. Our Fight Club members bought all the tickets. 12,000 tickets sold out in, I think, an hour and a half.
Wow.
And do you have, I mean, it might be a little bit soon to ask you, do you guys have a possible challenger for the winner of that fight?
Yeah, I mean, it could be Chuck Congo.
You wouldn't happen to bring in somebody from another, say, another organization and kind of cross-promote? Because I think that...
That's what we're all looking for.
Yeah, I'm just saying, like, I hear that they're doing that overseas. Who is, Affliction is supposedly cross-promoting with someone else?
I have no clue.
Yeah, I've heard that.
Yeah,
so
those guys need to do whatever the hell they can do to make some money. They're about to go out of business. I honestly still can't believe they're in business.
Dana, do you think that without Fedor, they're finished?
Yeah.
And
I think with Fedor, they're finished. I think they're just finished.
All right.
They've blown millions and millions of dollars. And they're trying to. I don't know what they're trying to do. Listen, at the end of the day, when you stop focusing on what you do, these guys sell T-shirts for a living, okay? And, their whole T-shirt thing is, I don't know. It seems pretty much like a fad to me. You need to focus on what it is you do for a living, and they're not fight promoters. That's not what they do, and they've lost millions of dollars trying to do it. And, I don't think they're going to be around much longer.
No, it's like you've said in the past that his camp is really difficult to deal with, to set something up. And then I hear, well, no, it's because Dana wants him to leave them and be exclusive with UFC. And that was what the issue is. Is there any shot of a cross promotion or were you only allowed if he's with the UFC?
No, I've tried to come to a deal with him before he was with them. You know, we went in and bought the Pride organization from Japan. And his contract was hanging out there. His contract was up with them. I tried to do a deal with him before them. So it has nothing to do with them. These guys aren't even players in this sport. I mean, this is between, you know, us and Fedor, whether we end up getting him or not. They're not, you know, in the mix whatsoever.
Yeah, you want Fedor,
They're the least of my concerns. Hmm. Exactly. Here's the thing. Do I want Fedor? I want Fedor if Fedor wants to come over here. If this guy doesn't want to fight the best in the world, what am I going to do? Chase this guy around and beg him to fight? No. Listen, I pay my respect to the guys who fight consistently, the best fighters in the world. George St. Pierre, even Anderson Silva. He didn't have the best performance the other night, but this guy consistently fights the best fighters in the world. Chuck Liddell, Shogun Hua. I mean, the list goes on and on. These are guys who consistently fight the best guys in the world, you know? Fedor is one of those guys.
How old is Fedor? He's in his early 30s, isn't he?
I honestly have no idea how old he is.
I know he's not a very old guy. I mean, you can have a nice few years. I think the fight that everybody really wants to see is, let's say Lesnar-Mir fight, and a lot of people anticipate that Mir won't win twice, that Lesnar will win. I think a lot of people would love to see Fedor Lesnar, even though Lesnar, what does he get, like four now fights or five fights?
Yeah, no, I'd love to see that fight, too. Believe me, I'd love to see that fight. I'm in the fight business. I love making the best fights in the world with the best fighters in the world. You know, but I've been trying to do a deal with this guy forever. I mean, you know, people always look at me and say, hey, why can't you get Fedor? What are you doing? Get Fedor done. Trust me. Do you guys think I don't want to get Fedor? Of course I do. I'd love to. If that's what the fans want, then that's what I want. And believe me, it takes two to do a deal.
Yeah. We got Mars in studio. Mars, you got a question for Dana White? You're a big UFC guy.
Mars is our engineer, and he always wants to talk to the fighters, and he always wants to ask questions, and he's very shy. So why don't you just ask a question?
Yeah, what's wrong with you? Don't be shy.
Hi, Dana. I was just caught off guard here. What to ask you?
All shy and nervous.
What to ask you?
He knows what he wants. Just ask him.
Just ask him?
Yeah.
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 We, by the way, we had Fedor in. We talked to him for an hour. We talked to his guy, and he seems like a very soft-spoken, nice man. We kept bringing up UFC, and he just wouldn't shit-talk anybody. We were trying to get like something going, and he was just like, "Oh no, I like him. I respect him. He's a wonderful fighter." I was like, "All right."
Yeah, no, yeah. From what I hear, he's, you know, he's a nice guy. He's pretty easy going, and yeah, I've heard that from everybody. You realize this? We've been trying to negotiate getting Fedor to the UFC forever. I've never even met Fedor.
Really?
We did.
Even met him.
He's got a weird vibe.
My point is, Fedor isn't controlling his own career. You know, his manager is.
Yeah.
He doesn't have a menacing vibe to him. I mean, it's real. Like a lot of those guys, like even Chuck, who's a really nice guy, has this air of a fighter. But Fedor came in just wearing a sweater, and he was just very quiet and soft spoken, and it was almost more threatening because he was so not the energy of a fighter.
Looks like a religious guy.
Yeah, he really does. He seems like he's a religious dude. He wouldn't talk about banging girls. He seems like a nice fellow.
That's funny.
Mars, no questions?
No.
Mars, what's wrong?
Mars is scared. And like, you'll hang up, and he'll have 50 things he wanted to ask you.
He was very excited that we were having you on the show today, Dana.
No, actually, I was talking to a friend of mine about Fedor.
A friend, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh. And I said how menacing he looked to me because he was so cool and calm. And the other individual swore to God that he was a power bottom. Okay. Dana?
Let it sit there.
Whoa. Dana, that was the last appearance you'll ever hear of Mars, our engineer.
You blew it!
Wow.
Thanks, Jim.
He's this Mars. Don't you have something to go tweak?
Now go home and get your fucking shine box.
All right. So... my forehead is itching.
Yeah, that was a tough one.
All right, so...
when you're not sure if there was a joke there or not, and then you realize there was supposed to be, but there's a huge void.
Yeah. I have no idea what he was even talking about.
I don't either.
Actually, I was reaching out for some help, and someone threw an anchor at me.
Help. Ooh. All right, Mars, thanks.
You're welcome. All right, well, Dana.
Well, Dana, that brought everything to us.
Yeah, nice that's way to really nice. Wrap up the interview. We figured he'd have a great question for you. And any
other big UFC news that we haven't touched on?
Actually, that's it. I'm in Philly about to walk into a meeting, actually.
All right. All right. Have fun in Philly.
You know what? Thank you guys so much for the support. I appreciate it. You guys are the best.
Yeah, we want to do something with you guys for the next event. We really do.
Yeah.
Love to have you guys, man. I'd love to have you guys out. Whatever you want to do, I'm in.
All right. I want my photo on the big Trinitron screen like a celebrity. Jim Norton. And they'll all just stare at it and go, who is that fucking mush-necked nothing? And then you can show some other hot chick. All right.
Done. We're doing it. We're going to put you up on the screen.
All right, Dana.
Thanks, Dana. Dana White, everyone.
Appreciate it.
Okay. Later, man.
Here's what I like about him. I like the fact that he's just saying, like, nah, man, Chuck should step aside.
He's done.
He is. It's like, he's done. Boxing promoters would never fucking do that. They will literally let a guy walk out there when he's 46 years old and get floored.
Yeah,
it's just
and just
silly.
Get like, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, they don't care. What?
All right, Mars, way to go.
Yeah, that was a good one, Mars.
Wow.
Yeah, we'll never have Dana back. That's terrific.
Oh, no, we'll have Dana back.
Did you think power bottom is just going to be the big kicker line and everyone's going to laugh? And oh, God, Mars. Anyway, Dana, what do you think?
No, actually, I thought someone was going to come in and team up and help me out. Yes.
Do you know this show?
Mars, you know this stuff, though. You don't have
one. How is anyone going to help?
You don't have one UFC question to ask the guy that
like
owns
the
company?
UFC.
I was good to go. I was caught off guard.
All right. Mars, thank you. Mayor Bloomberg, the mayor of New York City.
Speaking of power bottoms.
Yells at a reporter in a wheelchair who accidentally played music at a press conference and couldn't turn it off.
Why couldn't he? What was he, fucking an iPod attached to his foot?
Well, there was a press conference and Bloomberg took the podium. It was Patterson's news conference. Bloomberg apparently became annoyed at a disabled reporter after his electronic device started to play music. Take a look at this.
It's a little bit too important for playing music. Let me start again as soon as we can do this.
For nearly 2 minutes, Bloomberg stared at the reporter before resuming. The sound was coming from Michael Harris's tape recorder. Now, Harris, who is in a wheelchair, couldn't reach the device that he accidentally turned on. He told reporters that he was embarrassed that the mayor had singled him out, and Harris now wants an apology for that stare down from Mayor Bloomberg.
Apology. Everyone wants an apology.
Apology.
For what? Don't put your fucking tape where it can go off and you can't reach it, fucking twisted feet.
Well, however he turned it on, he should turn it off the same way.
Yeah, how did he turn it on? What, did he turn it on and throw it like a grenade? The fuck?
If you accidentally turned it on with your tongue, turn it off with your tongue, too.
If the mayor's staring you down like that, why wouldn't you say, I'm sorry, Mr. Mayor, I'm in a wheelchair, I cannot reach it, I apologize. Could someone grab that for me?
Yeah.
You know, why don't you want an apology? Yell at God. Fucking mayor didn't bend up your legs.
Believe me, no fans of the old mayor here.
He's a douche.
God, he's too much. He's already running his re-election commercials and everything. For his unprecedented third term or whatever the frick.
What's his approval rating? You think the people in the city like him?
I think with the city and the condition it's in, they kind of want to stick with it and see what he can do because he's like a finance guy.
Yeah.
But he's more another one of these, you know, tax the shit out of everybody and that'll fix the problem, guys.
Tax.
Well, he wasn't a Republican. He was a Democrat. And then he couldn't get on the Democratic ticket. And he went on the Republican.
Changed
the
Republican and then he went independent.
Yeah,
Obama's another one with these just tax. Now he's saying, though, that he's going to, because everybody's been clamoring. Opie was completely right when he said business as usual. Doesn't matter that a new guy's getting in. It's the first African-American president, blah, 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 blah. Business as usual as far as him being a Democrat, getting in office. Because now he's heard the people clamoring like, hey, you're taxing the fuck out of us. What are you doing? Why not cut back on some of the government spending? And now, what does he come out with? We're going to cut back on government spending because people said it, and I want my polls to be good.
He wants to keep those polls way up there. When people were yelling for change, you got to change the system, not another guy in the same system.
Yeah.
Real change would be having a real third-party candidate. That's change.
Viable
that's like,
option.
Wow, this is really different.
Yeah.
Not the same old crap.
Same crap. Same Democratic crap, though, instead of the same Republican crap.
I was thinking about this because you and Hannity were talking about taxes and stuff. And be honest. Yeah. Obviously, Obama taxing the shit out of people that are making money, okay?
Yeah.
Now, if McCain was the president, how much less taxes would you be paying? Out of curiosity, less is always better. I understand that. But would it be drastically less?
I think it would be drastically less.
For real?
For me, because they consider that upper echelon, you know, free pickings. Because it's very hard for you to come up with a defense that I make too much money to be taxed like this. You know, the common man doesn't want to hear it. It's more like, you know, just bail us out. Help us out here. But I think it would be a lot. The trouble is, like he's saying now, there won't be any sacred cows as far as this government spending cut that he wants to do. But there will be. He's going to cut programs that Democrats normally cut.
Sure.
And, keep the programs that Democrats normally keep.
Mm-hmm. Well, one thing is this. If he said, like, I'm going to not cut spending, and then people protested, and he goes, all right, I will cut spending, I like that. Like, I like a guy. There's a really weird line between sticking with what you said and a guy who sees that people aren't liking it and goes, all right, well, if this is what you want, this is what we'll do.
Let me tell you something, though. When they did that Tea Party teabag protest, he looked at that and blew it off like he didn't even know what it meant. He said, they said, what are the president's comments on so many people coming out and protesting the taxes? Well, President Obama, his comment was he had no idea this was even going on.
That's
and
such
then
a
couple of days later, he comes out with, we are going to cut spending. It doesn't come across to me as sincere as being, it's a poll reading. It's something Bill Clinton notoriously did, is seeing what the people want to do, not acknowledging that it's the people's thing. It's me. I'm just coming up with a great idea. He's the guy that comes up with a great idea after people already came up with it, Steve.
Well, you know what it is, the poll reading, but Fox were the ones really pushing the Tea Party, so he probably didn't want to look like he had changed policy or his thought process because of Fox News.
Yeah. Regardless of what it was, he knew people wanted spending cuts before they wanted taxes. And his big thing was tax, tax, tax. And now it's spending cuts. Which, you know something? Good. Let him cut some spending. I want to see some of these programs that are useless get just wiped off the slate and save some money that way.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
That's the Obama thing.
Yeah. Obama.
And what? He met Hugo Chavez and.
Oh, yeah. Apparently they're shaking hands and, you know, did he bow to him?
That's good, right?
Yeah. It's good to, you know, get to really know what, in essence, is a dictator. Some guy that mayors from some of his cities are leaving the country under threats of death. And because they're allowing the populace of these cities to actually speak their mind about Chavez. So then Chavez's people come in, tell the mayor that they're going to kill him, get out, put some other guy in place that allows this. There's one station left that actually, one TV station left that actually criticizes Chavez. And they're looking to take that over and shut that down. This guy is a dictator. He's a dictator. He won an unprecedented 800th term. You know, it's one of those. I love those things where they actually put out polling boxes. It's like, yeah, okay, he's running again.
I love the voters of those countries. Those silly bastards think they're going to make a change.
Why are you coming out? The guy is just going to stay there.
I'm sure the same thing happens in this country. All right, I guess we got to
put the
black guy in this time.
The guise of democracy.
Let's make sure that happens.
But yeah, him shaking hands at this guy. I mean, it's Obama's world tour is him kissing Heine on everybody that he believes Bush upset. Bush upset people because that was the times we were going through. If you remember, very shortly after 9/11, everyone was very gung-ho about what George Bush was doing. How the world looked at us, it was like, go F yourself. We're America. We were attacked, and we're going to do everything we have to do to not be attacked again. This isn't a popularity contest. We don't care what France or Venezuela or any other fucking country thinks of us. We have to do what's best for us. That's what everyone was saying when there were flags rattling off of everybody's SUVs on the highway. And God Bless America was playing everywhere. And Never Forget was on everybody's rear windows of their pickup trucks and bumper stickers. Yep. Now, it's the Kiss-Ass World Tour starring President Obama, where he's going around to these dictators and former terrorists who are now leaders of countries. Don't forget, Ahmadinejad was one of the original terrorists that held our hostages back in the 80s. He was one of the guys. And now he's in charge of Iran. And, you know, a little ass kiss in there. It's just years ago, right after 9/11, we didn't want what we have now. But for some reason, all those Never Forget, I guess people forgot.
A little bit.
A little bit. A little bit.
A little bit. A little bit.
Yep. Little Oops. Bit.
And what's up with this book I'm hearing about?
Hugo? I don't know anything about books.
He gave him Chavez handed him a couple
stupid
of
stupid books.
A copy of Happy Endings.
Was that it?
Yeah.
Well, how great would that be?
Can you imagine?
This guy's hysterical. Yeah. He's a scream.
Yeah, he likes to get jerked off.
Can you imagine? Because I guess Hugo Chavez gave
Steve from Bayshore. It was not Uncle Tom's Cabin. Now that would be inappropriate.
Chavez gives Obama a book. It went from 54,295 on the list, the Amazon book list, to number five.
Well, Chavez is like Oprah.
We're a bunch of lemmings. Yeah.
It's the new Oprah book of the Chavez Book of the Month Club.
Club.
How to purge a city of dissidents.
The book he gave Obama, Open Veins of Latin America, 5 centuries of the pillage of a continent.
Oh, is that it?
By a Uruguayan.
Booty hooty hoo. Shut up.
By a Uruguayan.
You and your book.
All right.
Yeah, they looked a little buddy-buddy there. I don't know. It's just that open hole,
he's
you know,
just trying to make
shake
friends.
Hands and make friends with everybody thing that's going to be the death of the country.
We'll see how it plays out in the end. Yeah. Who knows?
We'll see.
You want to talk about young girls?
Ah.
Young girls.
Who doesn't?
Yeah. Go from Obama to Uncle young
girls. Paul. Not that young, is it?
It might be. Young girls find 4 people having sex in Taco Bell bathroom.
Mm.
Four people.
I'm loving these fast food restaurant stories.
Yeah, and YouTube videos and everything
else. I
love
them.
Honking friggin'.
I know it's gross.
Snot rockets on your sandwiches.
When the guy took whatever it was, that sandwich, and farted on it. I'm sorry.
You know what? That's
always
just funny because it really isn't going to do any damage to the food, but it's hysterical.
Always
to see.
Funny.
It's like, why are you farting on the food?
Nobody, really nobody wants their sandwich farted on.
No,
it's universal.
But as long as it's not your sandwich, it's funny, right?
Yeah, but you never know.
You think you've eaten something from a restaurant that had bad things done to it,
dude? Guaranteed. Whoever
to say it. Absolutely.
If you're in your 30s or 40s and you've been to restaurants, you've eaten something that would horrify you.
Let me do a
snot.
Let me do a test, and I'm going to be completely honest with you. Mm-hmm. If I get a plate of food from a restaurant and I see that long, not short, the key is not short, long black hair in my food, what would you do?
I'd pick it out and eat it.
You would, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Really? Like
yeah.
I have you for the guy that just give me the check. I'm out of here.
You know what? Hair is all over the fucking place. What are you going to do about
I'm
it?
I'm the same way. A lot of people will go, I can't eat this. I'm
I
like,
eat that part.
I pull the hair
yeah,
out.
Yeah, I might actually scoop where the hair yeah, was, but there's
maybe chop
hair
it up
everywhere.
A little. Really?
Not a short little curly one, yeah.
Oh, the curly one, that's where I draw the line. That's
pubes.
Wow, you just surprised me. I really thought you were the guy that would be no effing way can I eat.
It's sitting at the bottom of two divots that you know balls were dipped in your fucking food.
No one wants their mashed potatoes to be served with two ball marks.
I picked a hair out of my food, though, and even yeah. a little like a little fruit fly. Type
oh,
bug.
That's easy
not a big
too.
Cockroach in or
no,
anything.
That's easy
but like
too.
A fruit fly, you take them, flick them out. And,
yeah, boy, if it's in your soup.
Depends on how hungry you are.
A tiny little, like, little.
Yeah, yeah.
In your soup, that's easy.
If I'm really hungry, you know, I don't care.
Wow, I'm surprised. What about you, Jimmy? Hair in your food?
I've had
it,
but yeah, it's almost like it's one of those things in life. It's like, how fucking crazy do I want to be? You're touching doorknobs, you're living. If it has a crab on it, I'd probably not eat it, but one hair
on.
Gives a shit. I would just pull it out.
Yeah. Comes out. It's covered in whatever. Oh. Jimmy Callis.
Eat it.
Jimmy Callis.
Do you like Jimmy Callis?
I kind of like Jimmy Callis. Kind of like. Now that you're doing the foot part of the bit, too.
Yes, from now on I will stomp my foot.
Young girls find four people having sex in Taco Bell bathroom. Mm. I'm sure Taco Bell is thrilled today.
Yeah.
Are they a sponsor? Are we allowed to do this?
It's a news story. We're not making any accusations.
Two young children walk into a downtown restaurant bathroom and see four people having sex. Their parents are so disturbed, they want all parents to be aware of the situation.
Why can't we see this stuff?
No.
Why does it always have to be?
Why can't we be having sex in the bathroom at Taco Bell?
Why does this always go to someone that doesn't appreciate us? Would you like to see people having sex in a bathroom?
Why not
it would,
walk
it would,
in
it would
and see that?
Perk up your day.
Be great. You just kick back.
Disturbed. They want all parents to be aware of the situation. Alana Greenfogel met with the family today.
Happens.
Alana, what restaurant are we talking about?
Terry, this particular incident happened at the Taco Bell. And
he was deep in her taco.
Tuna taco.
Why did she have to say this particular incident?
Yeah.
We know which one you mean, asshole.
The only one.
Yeah.
Hopefully
and it's like
the
they want
one.
To be aware of these situations. Like, watch out when you send your kids into a bathroom because there might be sex going on.
But it's almost like if he said there was sex in the bathroom of a fast food restaurant, and she said, parents were outraged, and he said, this incident, you mean? And she went, no, this was the McDonald's one in 75. No shit, idiot. You know which one you're fucking talking about.
This particular incident happened at the Taco Bell in downtown South Bend, but police say people have sex everywhere and anywhere.
The lunch experience for one family south of the border.
Definitely not family friendly.
Goes beyond borderline disturbing.
While they were eating, the youngest had to use the restroom.
So 5-year-old Emma was escorted by her 11-year-old sister. And when they pushed open the bathroom door,
they saw two women servicing two men in the restroom.
Get the fuck out of here.
Who pulled that off?
Holy shit, two.
Could you find a smellier place to get your dick sucked?
Oh, man.
A fucking Taco Bell toilet? Holy shit. What game these guys must have.
I like Fernando. He was nice.
By getting you to suck his dick in a Taco Bell toilet.
Taco Bell toilet?
Two.
Jerk. And when they pushed open the bathroom door,
they saw two women servicing two men in the restroom.
My 11-year-old asked me, how come two women were coming out of the bathroom and why were two guys in there? And they were making funny noises.
11 years old is not still not old enough to start learning about such things as that.
As parents, we're supposed to protect our children, not put them in harm's way.
Oh, she got a little upset. Tears.
Put them in harm's way.
Was it in harm's way? The woman's mouth was over it.
Exactly. Why don't you fucking grow up a little bit? It happens. Two people were they were fucking around, and there they shouldn't have been. They should have locked the door, and they didn't. So fucking live.
Yeah.
Nice.
Funny noises.
Yeah.
Charlie Callis was in there.
I just came.
We got more to the story. This is one of those just rare incidents. You're not going to keep your kids away from this
stuff, unfortunately.
Yeah, this
is one in a million. Come on.
It's one in a million. You're right.
I hope I would never have to explain to my 11-year-old child what would be going on.
I wouldn't want to see that.
No way.
That guy's a liar.
I would want to see that. And first of all, to explain it to your 11-year-old child, you wouldn't say, well, honey, what you did was walk in the bathroom. The women were sucking men's cocks, which is what you do when you want them to come in your mouth. It's not. Wouldn't you be like, well, they were doing something that grown-ups do in a very inappropriate place.
They shouldn't be doing it in the bathroom.
They shouldn't be doing it in there.
So obviously they're married.
Let's leave it at that. You know, it's just one of those things where it's you can explain it in a way where you don't have to fucking go into detail, dummy.
You see, he was deep dicking the girl.
Yes, yes. That's usually what happens before he sticks it inside her pussy. You get it?
What idiot 11-year-old doesn't know what a blowjob is? I knew what that was when I was in fucking third grade.
Of course you did. You were giving him.
Well, all right, I'm an exception. But who doesn't know what that is?
And if the woman's having her time of the month, you stick it in her shitter.
That is true. But although up to, no, I guess that was like seven. I used to think to get a woman pregnant, you had to fuck her in the ass with a rubber on. I thought the rubber had the stuff on it that made the girl pregnant.
That's not outrageous. Cause
I know.
That's not outrageous because Ira from Friday's show, I do believe he thinks the asshole was the vagina.
Yeah, he did.
I think he did.
Yeah.
And he's 65. I think he thinks girls pee out of their vagina, so that's like just their pee area.
Yeah.
And then you bang him in the shitter.
But to put in a rubber and fuck her in the ass, you did the least pregnant activities.
I know. That's like, you know, but I think I was seven when I thought that.
I don't care if
you're one.
And
I don't know why. Yeah, I know. I don't know why. And I didn't understand because, you know what, I think because people called it a scumbag. You know, they'd call the rubber a scumbag. So I thought it had the scum on it, which is the stuff that got the woman pregnant. And then I didn't know, you know, about the vagina, really. I didn't have one. So I just thought you stuck it up the girl's ass. Because I wasn't too sure about the differences, you know, between guys and girls' anatomy.
Now that I think about it, I think I thought the same thing. Except for the stuff on the rubber.
Oh, the magical
stuff.
That's insane. And then I started actually thinking about, well, why can't a girl just take the scumbag and put it on something? And then put it up her ass, and she wouldn't even need men. You know? And that's when I think I started asking questions.
Who set you straight?
School.
Your dad probably sat you down and was like, Jesus.
No, it wasn't dad.
Christ.
Definitely
this
wasn't dad.
This is how you do it.
It was school. It was school. Some fucking kid at school knew the whole deal.
Apparently, you still think rubbers get girls pregnant. You won't wear them.
Yes. I steer clear of those nasty old things. Don't want to get a girl pregnant. Take that rubber off. It's dangerous.
I like to go ass to pussy and then go, here, you work out the bacterial mess. Not my. That's a you problem, not a me problem.
There was always a kid at school that thought he had the knowledge to tell the rest of us.
Yeah.
Go see John. He knows.
He knows, but
he'll answer all your questions.
It's like, yeah, he always had it wrong. How does a girl get pregnant?
I'm trying to remember some of the stuff I was told by these idiots that thought they had knowledge.
I think it was a big story. I think I remember a story being told by some kid about how a girl gets pregnant. And I didn't chime in with my theory after I heard his theory.
What was his theory?
Because mine then sounded ridiculous.
His theory was the right theory?
It takes the dick and puts it in a vagina. Yeah, his was a theory that made a little more sense. I decided not to give my side of it and do a little more research.
Yeah, well, he had a better theory, like you jerk off on plastic and then slip and slide until you get knocked up. Your theory stunk.
Mine was really stupid.
What else did you think? You get her pregnant carrying her books?
Yes. Could happen.
Anthony.
I hope I would never have to explain to my 11-year-old child what would be going on.
I wouldn't want to see that.
No way.
The Schumanns are still shaken up.
This is getting lonely.
And only hope other children won't ever see what their kids saw.
I was fuming. I was angry. I was upset. I was concerned.
What else?
It's scary because now I don't want to send my children to the bathroom by themselves. And
right.
My 11-year-old doesn't want to be treated like a child. She wants to feel grown up.
Well,
and I can't do that now.
Oh, what's
fucking
wrong with
baby?
You?
This shut woman, up.
Is that the mother of the girl?
Yeah,
of
course. Gotta be. Okay. Thinks her kid's innocence right, so have just been scooped away from
what
them.
An asshole. Fucking, would you have preferred the kid walked in and someone was shitting?
Yeah, I know. That's another one. Some tippy Tom in the air. Shut the door. I'm taking a shit.
Fucking guy crying. That's a lawsuit. She's just doing that for a lawsuit.
Oh, yeah, that's a big
one. The
Schumanns
contacted Taco Bell because they want the bathroom doors to stay locked to prevent people from just wandering in. Robert says at first a manager told him they wouldn't do that, even though they found people having sex before. Well, today a Taco Bell...
Where's this Taco Bell?
Wow.
This probably didn't want homeless people fucking around. There are people shooting up.
That's,
what the fuck's going on at this Taco Bell, though?
Some fucking in the bathroom, apparently.
In the open, this Taco Bell's got to be in a weird area.
Yeah.
Yes, Danny.
It's in South Bend, Indiana.
Really?
Yep. South Bend, huh?
That's like the safest place in the world.
Who knew?
Isn't it?
I would imagine.
I like having sex there.
Having sex before. Well, today, a Taco Bell spokesperson sent us this statement. The safety of our customers is our number one priority. And although this is an isolated incident, we're having self-locking doors installed as a precautionary measure.
I love that. The safety of the customer is their number one concern. Mm-hmm. No, it isn't. Making fucking money. Why? Be honest. I would say the safety of our customer is the second most important concern we have.
I think it's a lot lower
What's
than that.
What's the first one?
Because it doesn't even come into your mind that people aren't safe coming into your place.
Of course not.
Exactly. Cleaning the loads off the floor should be second.
Yeah.
Safety third, because the guy will slip on it and crack his head. They actually hire cum cleaners. They have
squeegees.
Yeah, squeegees and little teeny mops. Nobody wants that gig.
The teeny mop gig.
Then whenever you get the thin mop, you're like, ah, boy, I shouldn't have been late last week. Then you got to squeeze the mop over out and make a milkshake.
I would love to hear that over the loudspeaker as you're in the fast food restaurant.
Oh,
we need a cum cleaner in the men's room.
Men's room.
As you're online. Just sitting there.
We have a jism spill in the restroom. John, could you get in there, please? Yeah, take the squeegee. It's a big load. Don't let the kids in there. Just squeegee as much as you can down the drain on the floor and then mop up the rest of the cum. Yes, Taco Bell. Your order, please.
Youch.
Yowza.
Yeah, that's a good one. That's a good one.
It's a good story, huh?
Good story.
We got unlucky lottery. We got the Slumdog story after the break. That's really good.
Sticks with the whole kid topic.
And I think we got a Hulk Hogan update. We didn't play the actual audio. We could play that today. But
I'd love to hear that, man.
But then Linda Hogan is commenting today.
Oh,
we'll explain after the break.
Booty who?
She says someone has her sunglasses. Could they return them?
Okay.
Last night I think I shit the bed. Got so drunk I gave a dude head. Life is just a merciful blur when you pop a piss wasser. Piss wasser, don't drink it slow. 3 a.m. buy some low. sleep in the bathroom on the floor. What really matters anymore? All the crap you do all day, who fucking cares? Anyway, it's Waffle, this is beer. Drop drunk off of beer. Piss Waffle, drink all day. It helps your troubles go away. Yeah, yeah. Piss Waffle, cheap German lager for export only.
Opie and Anthony. Delicious. Jim Norton. And now Laszlo.
There's an ice cold piss Waffle about now. Yeah. Good stuff.
Good stuff.
Laszlo brought us gifts.
That's right.
Yes.
Brought you custom-made DSs. We have this hacker kid who customizes equipment, PCs, mod stuff. So he's been modding DSs in-house. And I brought Anthony one the other day.
Yes.
And you just brought me one. Nice with the DS. Nice.
Yeah, it's for Grand Theft Auto Chinatown Wars, which came out last month for the Nintendo DS.
Yeah, mature really rated. Cool. Yeah.
It's very different than Animal Crossing and Pokemon.
Yeah, I know. I usually see people playing some pretty fucking lame games on those.
Now, my first question, DS, what's up with the PSP, I guess, is what I want to know.
Supposedly there's a new one coming out. I've seen some.
Really? Because they're giving away the games. You go to Circuit City or Best Buy, they are giving away the PSP
Circuit
games.
Circuit City, you're going to be standing outside an
empty
store.
Well, sorry, yeah. Well, that's where I noticed this. So, yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
I got to update that. But they were just giving them away, and this was before Circuit City announced they were closing all their stores.
Yeah, there's a lot of games that are, you know, the prices are quite low on the PSP. And for some weird reason, before, cause there was like no decent games that came out for, because every game that comes out on the PSP, I buy it.
Yeah.
Right now I'm playing Resistance Retribution or whatever that one is.
Oh, is that good?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Good times.
I've been, and this is terrible because I've always been a huge, like, got to be great graphics and immersion and everything. Now I find myself sitting on the shitter playing little downloaded app games for my iPhone. There's that latest one, that goddamn air traffic controller one.
Yeah, I know.
It's like number one downloaded fucking thing. It's in the favorites.
It's
this whole thing. And there's a couple of little runways, and planes come in out of the sides of the screen, and you have to use your finger and just kind of make a flight path for them without having them collide. And after a while, there's just a shitload of planes on your screen vying for runway room, and you're taking the plane and shoving it off into some area where, you know, it could maybe be safe for a few seconds, and then you could sweep it back to the runway. I'm sitting there just playing this dumb fucking game.
My visual is I'd hate to be a person in one of your planes that you're moving all around the screen.
Oh, dude, some of my planes are like, we were going to the runway. What
planes
are you doing?
Can right. make 90-degree turns.
The, I put them in a loop. Yeah.
They're on the plane going, the finger of God.
Finger of God. Oh, finger of God. Yeah, I like put them around in a little circle and just try to get them out of the way for a little while. And then the worst, though, is when you have a plane going right along the peripheral of the screen, and out of nowhere another plane comes and hits it. It's like, come on,
that's not fair.
How am I supposed to see that coming? I need a bigger screen on my iPhone. I need dual iPhones so I can get like two screens.
I think people are starting to kind of bug because the iPhone is becoming the gaming platform.
Like, it is weird, man.
There's word that, you know, people at PSP and in DS kind of mm-hmm. going, wow, that thing kind of came out of nowhere.
Where it's just enough entertainment for like your spare time. It's not gaming, like, you know, like I like gaming, but I also play that stupid parking garage game.
What's that?
It's
where
a
you get a Hummer.
Oh,
in the back.
I know. What that
was. You get a blowjob in the parking garage.
You got to figure out how to get your car out of certain
spots. How to get your yellow Volkswagen.
Right.
Out of the garage, and the exit ramp to the garage is plugged up with like limousines and other cars, and you have to move them around, but they're very hard to move around because other cars are in the way. So you got to scramble them around, and then finally you're like, all right, if I move this, then I can move this one, and then I get this one out of the way, I can back the limo here, I do this, hey, the ramp's open. And then out goes the Volkswagen, and then you get a new screen.
Yeah, but that
times you.
Oh, sorry, but that's just a takeoff of the old game we were playing as kids, where you
hold that plastic square with the numbers.
Yeah, and you want to just line up all the numbers one through whatever it was,
or make a picture or something.
Right,
it's got
right.
the one empty space.
Yeah, that's
and you
all
click,
that is.
Click, 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 click. That's kind of the way it is. Yeah, but you're right though. A lot of games. If you look at some of the favorites or the most downloaded things, apps on the iPhone, Now, a lot of them are games. I'm not really into a lot of them. Those are two that I play a lot, though. But I'd rather play on a computer and or were, Xbox.
With this game, GTA Chinatown Wars, it's obviously not like the graphics that you get on a PSP or, you know, even if you're playing on an Xbox or whatever. But the gameplay stands out.
Yeah.
And it's the highest rated. We were shocked. It was the highest rated DS game in history.
Yeah.
Ever released for the platform.
It is. You know why? It's got that GTA edge to it. Where other games, not so much for that platform.
Dude, this morning it's on the train ride, I bought a bunch of heroin. And one of the great parts of the game is that you can run around town buying drugs from dealers, and you know which dealers will pay more for weed and which will pay more for acid. And so you can go over.
So you're like making money and...
I was having a conversation with somebody the other day, and we were saying, where's the best place to buy heroin? They're like, oh, on the Upper East Side. And I was like, yeah, dude, I've got a ton of acid I've got to unload. And this woman next to us goes, what are you fucking talking about?
That's great.
I was playing Vice City Stories one time head-to-head on a plane with Cousin Ed, and we were sitting there chasing each other around, you know, Vice City, shooting each other to pieces. And he goes, you got the fucking grenade, don't you? And I go, yeah, I got the fucking grenade. You got the rocket launcher, don't you? He's like, yeah, I got the rocket launcher. And these fucking people sitting around us were so nervous.
Yeah, you probably shouldn't say that on a plane.
I gotta call this game Recipe for Disaster.
Oh, Jimmy.
How's that Guinness?
Ah, fantastic. I cannot. I've been giving you kudos to your tap rigging. Laszlo put the tap and all the gauges,
tanks.
The pressure tanks.
What he set it up
and
for
everything,
you?
And set it up in
you
my
know
house.
How to set that up?
Yeah. Well, I did it at my house years ago, and then friends started enjoying beer on tap at my place.
Yeah.
Like, can you do that at my crib? But I've never done Guinness before, and it's funny, when you come over to Anthony's house and he's not there, everybody acts like his posse. And so I roll in, and Anthony's just arriving at the airport, and so Danny comes to the door, and he's like, you never been downstairs before, have you? And I was like, no, you know, I've hung out around the pool and stuff like that. And he's like, yeah, it's nice when Anthony's not here, then I can sort of show the place around like it's my own. So then we roll downstairs. He's like, here's the fucking theater, bitch.
It's nice to pretend like it's your own Cribs episode. Like, I just want to film like my own Cribs and then send it to people I used to hate back in the day.
You
should do that.
Here's my theater.
That's
yo.
Funny.
So, and I
talk all gangsta and shit.
Oh, he does. And we go over to Anthony's bar, which is this beautiful piece of custom woodwork that this guy must have spent months building. That is
John Dreyer, who is fantastic.
It looks more expensive than my entire house, this bar. It's got the beautiful glass in the back and all the beautiful woodworking. And so I bring all this equipment in, including this high-pressure tank of nitrogen that you need to have Guinness
now,
on tap.
Now, the difference now, give people the difference between the CO2 tank pressure and the nitrogen pressure. CO2 is for, like, Budweiser and things like that, but Guinness needs nitrogen.
Yeah.
What's the difference in pressure?
The difference in pressure is like 1,800 pounds per square inch versus 30.
Yeah, you get 30 pounds off of a regular beer tap. Guinness, it's like 1,800 pounds of pressure. It's like torpedo.
Why?
I don't know why they need so much fucking pressure.
And if you knock the tank over and the top valve hits something, it's a rocket that will literally fly through concrete walls.
Yeah.
It is some spooky shit.
Compressed air, Marty!
So,
Martin, God damn it.
Whoa. Try it again.
Fuck that up. No,
try it again. Hold on, I got
some. And it's out of here!
Yeah.
Or is it? No, it's off the wall. My mistake. I thought the ball was gone, but apparently not.
Yeah. Damn, it's going for a Chief Brody thing.
So I'm very gingerly hooking this thing up to the Guinness tap, and I grab there's a release valve on the top of the tap, so I can sort of, you know, see what kind of pressure there is inside. I pull this release valve, and Guinness shot like a fucking fire hose all across the back wall of Anthony's beautiful bar. And everybody's face went like frozen place. And then the fear came in because Anthony's on the way back home from the airport. And there's like, he will be very angry. I was like, oh my.
Clean it up.
How many people get to live in your house when you're not there?
I don't know.
Dude, it is a fucking...
Liza, help me out here.
It is a sitcom. It's like people just walk in the door and it's like the applause. Hey, it's Fred from Brooklyn. And he comes in and then they walk out. I'm like, what kind of fucking place are you running here?
I know.
Your neighbors have to think you're dealing drugs, dude. The amount of cars that show up and people come in.
It's true.
And then wobble out.
At all hours. Things are happening. I'm not there and there's people over the house. And it is pretty pretty sitcom-ish.
But shortly after I hooked the Guinness up on tap, people were getting so blotto they were dropping their phones in the toilet. Which was
some people dropped their Blackberries in the toilet, Danny,
and still using it.
Now I got a new phone.
You got a new phone? Is that number that comes up now your new number or something?
No. I'm working. I'm doing the Jimmy tactic of the two phones.
Two. So okay.
When one's pissing you off, you could use the other, and then when iPhone pisses you off, you go back to the Blackberry.
Fucking A.
Danny turned me on to something. It was we're drinking Guinness. We go down to the bar. It's like, all right. First of all, he tells me that we're gonna wear the rug out. You're gonna like see the carpeting downstairs get worn out from going down for beers and coming back upstairs.
Because it just so happens that you end up, when you're over at Ann's house, you end up chilling on like those like kitchen island, and that just happens to be where people congregate. So to get another drink, you have to go down the stairs into the basement.
But why don't you do what the bars do and run a line from the basement?
Nah. We want to keep it down in the basement.
Well, then you should run one line up into the kitchen. That's obviously going
to
happen.
Next to the sink.
I bet you midsummer you're going to be sick of going downstairs, and it's going to happen.
No.
And then you run one outside.
Might have to put one in the cabana.
Yeah.
So, but Danny represents you like a true posse. He's fucked up. He'd had numerous beers, and I'm trying to get everything hooked up, but I didn't have all the parts for the Bud Light, because you've got two different taps. And I was like, I'm going to get the Guinness today, but I've got to go, to a welding supply store and get some more compressor regulators and so forth. And Danny's like, what the fuck? And I was like, no, it's just, I'll come over like tomorrow or the next day. He was like, oh, we're going to fucking do this now. I'm like, dude, it's fucking 7:30, 8 o'clock on a Thursday night. I was like, there's no welding supply store open that's going to have a fucking seat. So he was like, bullshit, I'm calling fucking Home Depot. And he's standing there right next to me on his iPhone. And he goes, English, motherfucker.
Since when do I talk like that?
Dude, when you're drinking.
Dude, when you drink, you are such a fucking homeboy. And so then he gets the guy on the phone. He's like, give me the motherfucking plumbing department. And he's like, yeah, we need a... What do we need, Laz? I'm like, we need a CO2 regulator. A CO2 regulator, motherfucker! Do you have it? And then they're like...
You don't remember talking like that, Danny? Danny keeps shaking his head over there.
God, and he's like, fuck you! And he hangs up. He's like, orange apron wearing motherfuckers, I'm calling Lowe's!
I'm like, dude, I swear they're not... It's a kind of a specialty item. I don't think they're going to have it.
Yeah, that's not an item you pick up at Home Depot.
But and then as soon as Anthony arrives to the front door, everybody starts stepping in. Look what we did! Boss, we set up some new stuff for you.
Ooh, this is nice.
Let me see what you guys did to my Guinness, house. Nice.
The Guinness and the Jack Daniels was what, like, was completely obliterating that night.
Yeah, I hadn't had that in a while. It was probably...
You were double fisting?
Yeah, well, no. I was putting Jack in the Guinness.
Jesus.
I know, like, I poured out a nice Guinness and everything, and Danny goes, you got to put some Jack in that. And I'm like, but I like the taste of Guinness. It's going to fuck it up. He goes, sweetens it up a little bit. So I'm like, I'll give it a try. So I dump a little in there. I'm like, wow, that does taste good. But I could tell you could have one of these. You have one, and that's it. And then Danny's
and
just
then you
like,
drop your phones in the toilet.
Fucking fucked up.
But that's not an Irish car bomb.
And I was going to ask, is that a real drink? I've never heard of that before.
It's kind
of,
I mean, you can do it. People drop shots in like.
I thought it was Jameson, right?
Yeah, it is.
Jameson and Guinness is an Irish car bomb.
Yeah, yeah.
So what's it going to take, Ant? Someone overdosing or someone just dying in the fucking house?
Jimmy was just absorbing this, looking at everyone talking, and just like, what the fuck is going on?
The colonel carrying a girl out with a bleeding nose.
You Boogie Nights. It's the set of Boogie Nights at my house.
And without the fucking.
Jeez.
The cool thing about dropping my phone in the toilet was that as drunk as I was, I knew that it's already in the toilet. So what am I going to do? Like, whether it's in there for another 8 seconds or not isn't really going to make much of a difference.
Would you just continue dropping the logs on top of it?
I just continue pissing on my phone.
It really doesn't matter.
It's like, really, what's the difference? It's wet.
That's wild.
And
it actually, but you continued to use it.
Yeah, actually,
because
was,
I called you and you're like, you were so, you're like, yeah, and I was like, what? I've never been this excited to hear from me. It's like, well, my phone was covered in shit, and now it works.
it finally dried out the next day, and like as the day went on, like more and more buttons were starting to work, but I hadn't gotten a phone call yet. So all of a sudden, I feel my phone start going off, and it was Lazo. So I pick up, I'm just like, yes. And he's like, what? I'm like, it works. He's like, why wouldn't it work? I'm like, I dropped my phone in the toilet. It still works.
I learned the hard way when you dump it in a toilet or a puddle. Take that fucking battery out immediately. Did you do that?
Yeah, I did. I went through.
Because if you don't, you fry up.
Can't do it.
You fry it up,
dude. It actually worked. It's the only thing that didn't work was like some of the buttons on the keyboard didn't work, but it was like really key buttons, like you know, like the back button and the trackball, like pressy in button. So
pressy in button.
What do you call
that? Stupid pressy in button.
My iPhone got submerged for seconds when we were having the party, and stupid fucking landscaper guy pushed me into the pool.
Do you still use him?
Yeah, because he's like the guy. You know.
Right, oh, yeah.
He knows he's an asshole. He knows
There's
call him an asshole.
8 million people in Long Island that will cut your hedges.
No, this isn't like that landscape guy. He's the guy that actually did all the setting up of the blue stone and all
is
that
he good?
Shit. Yeah, he's good, unfortunately. And rather, if he was shit, it would be great because then I'd just tell him to go fuck off. But he actually did pay for the iPhone. So I had to go and get it. But it was in the water for 2 seconds. I jumped back out, took it out of my pocket, and started like trying to flick the water out of it. And that thing just got like one of those things you put in your mittens.
Ski gloves, yeah.
When you're cold.
Yeah, the hand warmers.
Blazing hot, the phone.
That's
and
good.
It was over.
That's bad.
Yeah. It didn't work anymore.
I love a warm phone.
Yeah, it's a nice warm phone.
They will work again. You just got to get that battery out immediately. I don't know about the iPhone, but the BlackBerry definitely.
Can't iPhone, you can't take it out.
And you can't.
Oh, you can?
Nah, why would you? That'd be convenient.
I don't
know. That fucking asshole in his mum and Sean's fucking sweatshirt.
Dude, they
fucked Steve Jobs.
They did that on purpose, so
they
destroy phones.
Yeah, he's a prick.
Were you happy to see him get sick?
Nah, I don't want to see anybody get sick.
It's all one piece.
That's so stupid. I didn't know that until just now.
Yeah, you can't take the battery out. It's like you never were able to take it out of an iPod or anything. It's the same design. Yeah.
Same problem, though.
Same problem, too.
Yeah, because they want their stuff destroyed, so you go and get another one.
And if you drop your phone in the toilet, or even if it's in your pocket and you get caught in a rainstorm or something, and you go in and it stops, starts screwing around, you go in and be like, I don't know what happened to it. Bullshit, because they've got those little red dots inside that if it gets moisture, it turns red.
Yeah.
And then they know you're, because I've tried to lie my way through that. I don't know what happened, you know?
They know, because, there's a color-coded thing in the iPhone that if it gets wet, it changes color. Hmm. So when they open it up and you said, I don't know what happens, they go, yeah, we know.
And I tried,
it's fucking red dot.
I said, I have a very sweaty ball bag and I keep it in my front pocket.
I was very nervous waiting for a call.
Laszlo, what is the pirate thing about? The pirate bay?
Gar. Well, I guess it's the BitTorrent guys in Sweden.
They're going to jail, right?
I think one of them is.
Can you get a virus from BitTorrents?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And a lot of the times you'll see something on there like, oh, I'm going to download, the Terminator movie or whatever, and you download it and unzip it and suddenly your computer is...
Infection.
Right, is infected. but when people put like fake stuff up there, it's a bit nerve wracking downloading stuff.
You download, fuck it. You think you're downloading a movie and you're getting 2 hours of meat spin.
I had just the opposite problem. Wasn't a movie popped up.
But those guys have been really...
They fucked you over pretty good over the years, right?
Yeah. They'll change the face of their website to a GTA theme on the day a game comes out. And
the font, GTA looking.
It's just, they openly mock you. You just want to reach through the screen and kill. It's like, I worked on that game for a long time, you fucking jackass.
It's not like a lot of people are going to those sites for free stuff,
dude.
Oh, my God.
Dude, tons of people.
Yeah.
Why don't they, fucking release it the day before then? Why are they respecting the release date?
Who?
The guys.
The pirates?
Yeah.
Well, no, they take their games and crack it and post it.
But don't they do it the day the day before?
No, I'm saying the day it comes out.
They still got to get their copies, what Lazo's saying.
Right.
But
sometimes if there's leaks,
right.
Then
it'll be up
days before. Like that the Wolverine movie that wasn't done or whatever.
Not done yet and out it was.
And Fox fired the guy for reviewing it.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
Fair enough.
Wow.
Fair enough. Yeah, he reviewed the The stolen copy.
Stolen copy. What a dummy.
For a product that's owned by your parent company, stupid.
Yeah.
Oops.
He should have reviewed it and said, it's great. Asshole, don't give an honest opinion.
So it's not cool to get our stuff for free, Laszlo?
It's the copy.
Well, I'd say in some cases it's, but I don't know. You know, in this, like I was saying earlier, I see both sides of it, but I have to say it's quite frustrating when you see people that have worked their, whole professional life to make video games. And, you know, you've got studios like EA laying off 1,000 people. Video game studios are laying people off. Movies and video games are all America. That's all we've got left. That's all we make anymore. Mm-hmm. Well, we make really good bombs.
Yeah, we do that too. But, especially on this show.
Cars, the auto industry.
Oh, they're doing awesome. Yeah. So. You know, and I never want to be one of those people that's like, yeah, man, don't fucking steal. It's wrong.
Yeah.
But when you see, like, 30, 40% of your sales going to assholes who aren't paying for shit, it's like, you got to, it makes you angry.
They shouldn't steal it. Fuck them. They shouldn't steal it. You worked on it. They should buy it or not have it. There's nothing wrong with wanting to get paid for your shit. That's not being a dick, wanting your money and saying, look, just pay for what you. With the product.
So let's say people were somebody ripped the Lucky Louie box set and posted it up on, I'm sure it's there, but posting, they're downloading it. You're obviously not getting any.
Yeah, I'd be really annoyed at that. I mean, it's like.
Hey, pull up fucking BitTorrent and show him how much money he's losing.
Lucky Louie wouldn't bother me because I don't get anything from that anyway. They didn't push that hard enough. But you're right to be annoyed.
Well, Jimmy,
you should fucking pay for it.
I know where you're going. Your other stuff is up there.
I don't care. I mean, most people pay for my shit.
It still is a big problem. Yeah. I mean, the real fans will pay for it.
But it's annoying. The fucking people stealing your shit. Fuck that.
Yeah.
Yeah. The stuff you like, I mean, obviously you're not downloading the stuff you don't like. So it's like, if you really enjoy a game and you download it for free,
what?
You're screwed.
There's a few Jim Norton hits up here on Pirate Bay.
What?
Yeah.
Can you give us a number or?
Down and dirty. How do we get rid of them?
Look at that. How do we get rid of that?
I don't steal shit, man. I pay for my music on iTunes.
I think we're all on
Jim
Laszlo's
Ulrich
side.
Yeah, Lars was right. If it wasn't for Lars, you know what? Pushing fucking all these sites would be stealing. Our artists would make nothing.
Yeah.
And I originally thought it was like, what a bunch of pricks. They're fucking their fans. And then you sort of step back for a bit and you see how CD sales have fucking tanked. Nobody's buying CDs.
No.
None.
They did figure out a way to sell them online, though.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people do actually pay 99 cents for a tune, if you look at how much money iTunes is making. But, yeah, the freebie downloads, there's plenty of them.
And I'll get emails from people that say, like, oh, well, sometimes a game sucks and I'm really pissed off that I paid for it. I'm like, dude, that's called capitalism. Like, sometimes you buy a car and it's like, 6 months in, you're like, this sucks balls, fucking car. But you don't just go to the Ford dealership and fucking jack one and be like, hey, I'm going to try it out for a while. You got a problem with that?
Yeah, people don't look at it as an actual product. They don't look at it like something that you should be arrested for stealing. If you walked into a store and just grabbed something, what? I'm just taking it.
And I love the thing of like, if I like it, then I go and I pay for it. No, you don't.
No,
because I've
for
said
it.
That and I didn't pay for it.
No one pays for it.
I'm all for paying for the stuff.
Yeah.
I don't steal music. So fucking.
There are things like, especially video games, where if there's too many people stealing them, the company's not making money. They can't hire the talent that put the fun fucking good game together, and you come out with a piece of shit game and then you go, and then there's people, that company sucks. Your fucking game sucks.
And there are companies that used to develop a lot of PC games that don't even want to bother with it because PC games are so easy to pirate.
Very easy,
And the piracy rate's huge. And they're like, why would I do that? Why don't I just put it on Xbox and PS3 where it's a closed architecture system and it's a lot harder to pirate.
I know.
Jimmy, you want some numbers?
Oh, no.
I won't mention the site, but one of your things, I'll try to keep it vague, downloaded 3,060 times.
Well, is it from, what's the thing? Is it Down and Dirty, or is it fucking the One Night Stand?
Monster Ring.
Yeah, nothing you can do. I mean,
that's amazing.
Yeah. No, fucking, it's annoying, but what am I going to do?
Yeah.
I'm glad one of these scumbags is going to jail. The fucking pirate guy.
But they're refusing to pay the fine.
Yeah.
Which is what, 3 million, was it?
Yeah, it's like 3.6 million.
Well, they can't pay it. So once these guys start going to jail, because the bottom line is it's a new way to do business, and guys have just found out a way. Like, you can't just walk into a store and steal shit like you said. So guys have found out a way to rip it off, and they're trying to justify why it's okay to rip it off. Fuck you.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
You throw a couple of these guys in jail, it'll turn around.
They'll eventually stop. Once they start fucking locking guys up for stealing, because again, you everything you create now can be gotten digitally. So are we supposed to just give your shit away? It's fucking annoying.
Wait, I'm confused by Nick. This is for you, Laszlo. Nick in Chicago, what's up?
Yeah, what's up, man?
Hey.
Yeah, just, you know, I'm not advocating, you know, stealing software or anything. It's just, you know, it's just surprising to hear that one of the guys behind Grand Theft Auto franchise, you know, speaking out against stealing software.
Well, it's not like Laszlo goes out and starts shooting people and hitting hookers with crowbars, do you?
Oh, yeah. It's like, I'm not advocating that you actually sell heroin.
It's the game.
It's entertainment inside a video game that was released on the Nintendo DS.
How do you get your shit off these fucking sites?
You can't. It's over, Johnny.
You can't? Mm-hmm. Who runs them? It's those Swedish scumbags?
But once it's out, it's out.
Yeah, there's a bunch of different BitTorrent.
Yeah,
sites.
And one gets it,
it's much harder to take down, I think, than Napster.
Yeah.
Why?
Just because it's more shared over many
peer to peer more so than a central little location that people go to. These torrents.
It's amazing. I guess everyone's getting beaten with that, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you're not alone, Jimmy.
Oh no.
I think a solution to it will only cause a bigger problem as far as what we can access and how easy it'll be to access other stuff on
What's going to happen is the entertainment industry, a lot of times, completely knee-jerks and overreacts. And what they're going to do is start locking shit down and making it really annoying. I mean, even sometimes the DRM on the iPhone, I agree, or the iPod or whatever, will get annoying when you're trying to move your songs from one machine.
Oh,
it's just like, give me a fucking break.
I gave up. But like, whatever computer you have your songs on, you got to keep that one.
that one is such bullshit.
I know, but
that's so frustrating.
It's specifically for the purpose that they don't want your buddies coming over your house and transferring your songs onto their fucking systems.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it.
I wonder if that's one of the stipulations for the artists to give them the right to sell them. Maybe iTunes said, and we have a way that guarantees that you can only do it on a 2 or 3 computers. And that's maybe how they fucking cornered the market the way they did.
Yeah, they had to make those concessions to the record labels. But now they're doing the DRM-free bit, which on iTunes.
What's that?
Where you can download the song and move it wherever you want.
Mm.
There's no restrictions on it.
It's going to cost you more money, though.
It's going to cost you more money, though.
Yeah, per song.
I'm sure.
I think $1.29.
Yeah, they jacked it up like
30 cents.
Yeah, 30 cents a song.
That's worth it. To put it on all your
in a way, but in
shit.
A way we paid for these same fucking a lot of cases you paid for the same song 8 times. You Kiss Destroyer. I've had probably 11 copies of the record. I bought the fucking cassette. I bought the fucking CD. Jesus Christ!
Yeah,
I paid Gene to sing it to me over the phone.
Let's go to Andy in Allentown. Andy, what's up?
Hey guys, love the show.
Welcome aboard,
Andy.
Thank you, Jimmy. I saw you at Croc Rock on New Year's Eve.
Thank you.
So listen, I was reading the recent article in Rolling Stones about this Web Chief outfit over there in the UK that artists are now paying these firms that are made up of like copyright lawyers and whatnot to have them purge all these websites with their links onto bad material. And I guess there was a big suit with Prince who, you know, some questionably gay fan probably of Prince. Started a big petition about this company, and they were able to turn their decision around to let them do the same. It was unfair to these websites that are actually fan sites. I just wonder what you thought about that.
Well, Prince is fucking. It's a little easier when you're someone like Prince, and you've got the kind of money Prince does, where you're set for 30 lifetimes. It's like, you know, it's like for me, 3,600 copies of Monster Rain is a lot. That's a lot. Like HBO looks at my DVD sales, and they go, all right, what's going to determine if we give Jim a special? DVD sales are huge for fucking HBO.
Yeah.
So if people are stealing my shit like that, they are making it harder for me to get another special, because that's one of the only factors that HBO can determine, because they don't do a rating system. I'm not Metallica. I'm not fucking Prince. I'm not set for fucking a lifetime. You know what I mean? So it's like, it annoys me.
A couple things coming in. You guys don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Pirate Bay is a search engine. The site only points to where to get it. That's Rufus Butterbean.
Oh, yeah?
And then Blue Healer, usually good, but not today, Blue Healer. He writes, screener copies, conversation over. We get screener copies so we can see these movies before they hit theaters, and then we're helping promote the fuck out of them.
Screener copies are a promotional tool, and they're encoded.
I'm not copying screener copies.
It says Opie and Anthony on the screener copy. It's copying embedded in the fucking movie.
I like seeing that because it almost feels like we have a credit on that movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got a credit.
Says all of a sudden copy for Opie and Anthony.
Okay, nice.
Wow, look at that. We're part of the movie process.
And I give out promotional copies of my material as well. I'm not complaining. I give out a lot of books. You know what I mean? To radio stations and shit like that and fucking people I know. That's common practice.
I would have to say 90% of the screener copies I've gotten in the last few years, this is a new thing for our show. I've definitely talked about it on the air.
Yeah.
Every once in a while you get a dud and you're like, you know what? I don't talk about it because I don't want to give them bad marketing. If that makes sense. I just don't talk about it. Let's go to Peter in Massachusetts. This got the phones ringing, Laszlo. Peter, what's going on?
Hey, thanks for talking about this. Jimmy kind of touched on my point a little bit there. The record companies, music companies like Sony, they started out with LPs and they reissue everything on CD. And how much did it cost to print the CD? Not as much as in the beginning they were charging like $20 for a CD. It probably cost, who knows, I don't know what it cost, but it's probably around $3, really.
You're not paying for the hardware of a CD or a DVD or a game. You're not paying for the actual plastic of the disc. You're paying for what went.
That would be a mere sense, right?
You're paying for what went into the research and development and the recording and everything else behind it. For the information that's on that disc.
And their argument would be, Pete, not to interrupt you, but their argument would be, look, you bought the copy once. You don't have to buy it again. They're issuing it in different forms that are more convenient to listen to. Like a CD was a lot more convenient than a cassette or an 8-track or a record, and iTunes is much more convenient than a CD, so it's my choice to continually repurchase it.
Right, but I guess my point is the record companies have been making so much money off the artist that you really can't expect the average consumer to feel bad for the record company because they're losing money. On the artist side, yeah, I can see their point, but for the recording industry as a whole, they're a bunch of fucking assholes anyway.
That's true.
I was going to say, when I discovered Napster and I started downloading music for free, I didn't feel any guilt because I really did feel like sort of what this guy's saying.
And they're screwing over the record company, right?
That the record companies had us by the balls and they were taking advantage of the consumers and overcharging for a lot of their stuff. I didn't feel the guilt.
And it was hard to because they were fucking the band so badly. I mean, I remember when I worked at DRE, we'd have bands that had a hit fucking song on the radio. They were selling hundreds of thousands of records, and the guys are on food stamps.
And they were still living with mom and dad.
Right, out of a van. It's like, what the fuck? And it's because
they signed their lives away, a lot of these guys.
You know, and it's like, it's asinine.
And now, because of the system being changed, these guys are now making a lot more money because they're controlling most of the process now. Right?
Right. And you don't need the record company as much. I mean, you don't need them as a distribution network. And so some people argue that a lot of the money now goes to Apple, but fair enough.
They provided a fucking look. They were brilliant, man. The iPod, they revolutionized. It was fucking brilliant. Napster was dumb. They should have figured out a way to get the artist a little bit of money or cut the deals, but
let's go to Steven.
I just said nothing, by the way.
That's why I bailed you out with a phone call.
Thanks.
All right, Steve. We got Laszlo in studio talking about tech stuff.
I mean, not to interrupt Steve, but I think that people should pay for the music.
I'm sorry. I love this UN racism conference.
Hey, buddies. Hey, Laszlo. I just wanted to ask you. I've read that a lot of PC game manufacturers are actually going DRM free to help combat the piracy issue. Do you think that's going to help at all?
All right, listen, I don't know what DRM.
Digital rights management.
Thank you.
So they put
rights management.
Okay, yeah, they put some they put some restrictions on the disc to make it harder for people to copy it. There have been a couple of game companies that have done that, and I was talking recently to somebody at a video game company about this, and
they released a game, and the rate of piracy on it, they're like, yeah, it's DRM free, you know, everybody take care of us. The rate of piracy on it was 90%. So 9 out of 10 people downloaded it.
I read it was the exact opposite, so apparently my information was incorrect.
Or mine could be incorrect.
People are going to steal it, dude.
The thing that I really liked, going back to, like, the thing I liked about what id Software did with Doom and all those kind of games, they would give you a few levels. Like, here you go. Download it, play it, and, dude, you would get to the end of that last free level, and you're like, dude.
Must have game.
Must have it. And then you went and bought it.
Yeah.
And the thing is, like, they're not going to pay for it if you go, okay, you can steal it if you want. We prefer you don't. Because they're not stealing to hurt the artist. Like, 95% of the people that download shit for free, they're not, I mean, they like Metallica. They're not going, fuck Metallica, but it's financial. It's cheaper to steal it.
Mm-hmm.
That's why people steal. They don't steal to hurt you. They steal because it's fucking free.
I think the whole point was a lot of the people want to crack it just for the challenge of cracking it. And that kind of, if you eliminate the DRM, you would eliminate people wanting to crack it.
But then they don't have to crack it. They just put it up and people take it.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
It is a very.
Boy,
oh, wow. I like. Well, maybe I don't like this.
I want retina scans.
I got to be. I'm playing it both ways today because this phone call, this is a good one. Brandon in San Diego.
Hey, boys. What's going on?
Hey.
Hey, I got a couple things to see if I can keep you interested. There's a program on the internet. It's called SharePod. It just sucks. It doesn't work with the iTouches or the iPhones because they're flash drive. So you can put it on any iPod, and you can transfer any file to your computer from anyone's iPod.
And I'm sure it does something to the iPod after a while.
No, it's upgrade it. It's another program like iTunes. It works exactly like iTunes. You can eject it. It just transfers everything over. So I grab all my buddy's music that way, and I throw it onto my touch.
There you go.
Jesus.
Oh, you guys.
All right.
Yeah, there you go.
Let's say hi to Adam in Minnesota. Adam.
Hey, guys. Hey. Provocative show today. But what I'd like to do is...
What a douche.
But, yeah, I'd like to ask Laszlo about what do you think about old-school emulators on the internet? Like, for instance, like, I really want to play Altered Beast for the Sega, but, like, it's impossible to find that those game cartridges around anymore, like, even if you have the system or whatever. Like, the only way I could get to play these games is if I, like, downloaded them off the internet. And I'm actually playing some, like, you know, rich old games, but...
I got to play, like, Clueless Guy. What's an emulator?
Well, it's a piece of software that you download, and it allows you to... It emulates the platform from back then. Back to your point about Altered Beast. If there's a place, I don't know if you've heard of it, but it's called eBay, and it
Danny found it in seconds.
I've heard of eBay.
Assuming that you've still got those old platforms, but in most cases, people don't want to fire up an old Sega Genesis.
If I want to play Falcon's Maze?
Falcon's Maze.
Thank you, Danny.
Then you'll have to download the torrent
from the Whopper. I logged into the Whopper.
But like what this guy's saying, I mean, I've played with emulators and like they're fun and stuff. But I mean, I like playing classic games in the way that they're meant to be played. You know, on a larger screen, typically larger than a computer monitor, with a controller in my hand as opposed to a keyboard. So when I felt like I wanted to play some of these old school games, guess what I did? I went on eBay. I bought the old console for $20, like a Dreamcast. I got a Dreamcast for $20. You get game lots for $10-$15. I mean, it's possible to do.
You really enjoy those games though?
Yeah, man. Some of them are a lot of fun.
That sounds terrible.
I wonder who's making the money.
That's the unfunnest thing I've ever heard.
Right. You don't like that, Jimmy?
Unfunnest. Right.
What's wrong with Jimmy?
Then he goes back and watches some John Hughes films.
He does.
Fucking horrendous.
Playing some old GoldenEye on your old crusty N64. It's great.
Put on your laser disc and watch a fucking two-disc film. That sounds horrendous. Sega Genesis can kiss my fucking balls.
Nothing better than a nice side-scroller.
And television was fun.
Hey, I like the side-scroller. Let's go to Chuck in Cali.
Plink, plink, plink.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Chuck.
Coins.
Oh,
I'll hear the truck.
I'm glad you talk so.
DVDs and games.
Yeah. What, Chuck?
Yeah, guys walk up to your trucks out here at truck stops in California all the time, selling DVDs and anything like that pirated all the time.
Hard copy is a pirated
kind of language.
One guy wrote down his license plate number and everything like that.
Ooh, good man, you rat.
Number. And
rat. Whole family's rats.
Aren't you a goody gumdrops?
That guy's trying to feed his family. He's unemployed.
Yeah.
Let's go to Jared. Jared.
Fucking tattletale.
The man has the arm.
Hold on. He's the same guy calling people going, there's a chick that wants to blow me for $20 in my truck. Can you send the police, please?
You're not a fan of the tattletale.
No, I mean, I there's a line between stop stealing shit and fucking adamantier.
You're cracking me up today. Not a fan of the tattletale, huh?
No, how can
tattletale.
You be? I know this isn't an emergency, but look.
Let's go.
Hey, Jared, how's the marathon crowd?
Is it marathon day?
Yes. I wouldn't even know.
Motherfucker, it's Patriots Day in Boston.
Yes.
I know they had Pumpsy Green Boston night on person. Friday, by the way.
Well.
Do we have Pumpsy Green audio from the Red Sox game?
I'd like to think we're directly responsible for that one.
Yes, we are.
I kind of think we might be.
I think we guilted him into having to recognize Pumpsy Green.
You know who Pumpsy Green is, Laszlo?
No. He's uploading all video games. I wish I could.
Well, by the
I
way,
wish I said that better.
That wasn't.
I do too, Anthony.
Pumpsy Green night.
My own shit.
Pumpsy Green night was not what the original idea was to call it in Boston, but they said no. We have to name it after one of them.
Laszlo, Boston is so racist. They were the last to have a black baseball player, and his name, Pumpsy Green.
Pumpsy Green. Nice.
The first. 12 years after Robinson.
Yeah, 12 years after Jackie Robinson, the Red Sox.
12 years,
the Red Sox
Boston.
Went, you know what? I don't think this is a fad. I guess we're going to have to get a few of them.
We're losing, guys. I think we need a few of these
12
guys.
12 years after Jackie Robinson, those racist motherfuckers up there said, all right, get me one of them.
That town is full of animals, man. The Boston Marathon, which is going on this morning, I was at the last one because my chick was running it. And these guys, it's like most marathons you go to, there's people on the sidelines clapping, yay. Dude, in Boston, I've never seen anything like it. People have kegs set up by the
no
side
mic
of the
on
road.
Laszlo.
What?
Could barely hear you.
Well, hey, a lot of people are saying that, so that's
really?
Good to know. Yeah.
Hey, anyway.
All right. I think it's this button that's not lit right here.
Oh.
But I don't know how to light up that button.
I don't know about this new studio, dude. It's like one of your buddies who used to have a great house, and like his old lady kicks him out, and then you go over to his new place. He's got like a fucking hot plate.
Yeah.
You know, there's like
a
hubcap full of Marlboro Red butts.
Well, the main guy said it's going to be great. 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 You're here.
Got it.
Great, 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 great. Well, tell your marathon story.
Oh, but the guys in Boston, when they're watching the marathon, it's like it's a holiday in mm-hmm. Boston.
It's called Patriots Day, I believe.
Yeah, and people are just by the side of the road getting shit-faced. And you sit there and watch them drinking. And, of course, the Ethiopians always go by first, so they're making racist comments about...
Oh, yeah, of course.
You know, they have to run like that in their country to go get a fucking Coca-Cola. You got to go 100 miles.
Yeah. You know, when lions chasing you, you'd run fast, too. You know, the guy's, like, fucking living in the city and...
drives a Beamer.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, he's running to get something to eat.
Hey, yeah, they run to my... Hey! That's how your people talk, isn't it?
Huh? Have a sandwich.
You clicking motherfucker.
The guy was actually born in Houston. He doesn't even know where Ethiopia is on the map.
They run barefoot over there, the fucking savages.
That's what happened.
Hey, where's that Live Aid money? Where's that Live Aid money, motherfucker? We are the world.
Yeah, that's exactly it.
It's amazing how everyone from Brooklyn went to Boston recently.
Hey, I do two accents.
What do you got, Jared, from Boston?
Hey, guys. You guys know I'm hardcore. I love you guys. I've had satellite forever. Listen to you since AAF.
Hey, can I stop you for a second? Because there's a bunch of dummies out there. They're like, nope, Laszlo, I can hear him loud and clear. That's not what we're getting at.
I can't hear him on the phone.
Thank you. Thank you, Jared. And that's what we got to fix next. We're still tweaking this new studio. All right, you love the show. You've been listening for a while. Where's your
but,
point?
There's a butt coming.
What do you guys think about people downloading your show?
I'm sure
if you look on
happen.
Pirate Bay, it's all over the place.
No, that's not
They never download
that's
our
crazy.
Show.
That's...
I do it myself.
No,
that never happens.
So, I want to listen to every second of the show, so I'll listen live as long as I can. Today I'll listen to the whole show because I'm not working, but... You know, I'll throw it on the iPod, listen to it while I'm at work.
In all honesty, I'll tell you the other side of that, and which is the scary side of this whole thing. If our numbers are really bad here at SiriusXM, where they do research and ratings, and they go, wow, no one's listening to Opie and Anthony. But they are listening, but they're getting it for free, but that doesn't matter in this world.
No.
With their little report they do, we're done.
Well, I don't feel so bad because I mean I'm a paying customer. I just see it as a time and shift, as a shifting of where I'm listening. That's all.
But if too many of you guys do it and our numbers get down to a point, the company could actually go, you know what? They're not getting the job done for us, and we're going to have to move on from these guys.
I'll tell you a problem.
That's just the other side. That's all I'm saying.
One reason it doesn't bother me nearly as much is A, you're a paying customer, but B, we do 5 hours a day or whatever the show is lengthwise a day every week. The difference between that and a DVD is you work for a year to put together material to put out. You have one DVD.
Yeah.
We're doing fucking 5 hours a day. It's a different level of material coming out. When you put out a CD, you have that CD to sell for the next 2 years.
Yeah.
So it's just a different level of work that goes into it.
Right.
Yeah. I hear you.
All right, Jared. Thank you.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
Downloading the show, you bastard, you thief.
This guy's, he's got it. What do you got? You're from New York? I don't know your name. It's not on the screen.
Ray.
Yeah.
Ray.
Are you controlling Ray?
Ray, what's
up? A cool one to play right there.
Oh, you guys doing the big, you can call me Ray joke again?
Yes.
Fucking asshole.
It was funnier this time.
Good.
Hey, look, just on racist force.
But you doesn't have to call me douchebag. Go ahead, Ray. It's all about you.
I'm a retired New York City fireman.
God bless you, Ray.
Boston Fire Department. Back in the late 80s, early 90s, I think people started getting germophobic, and lots of fire departments were issuing firemen their own personal face masks. That way you didn't have to go to work and just use some mask. Hey, who was wearing this before me? Boston held out on that for years and years. We don't need it. We're a brotherhood. You know when they went out and bought all?
Oh, no.
Their very first black firefighter, before he graduated from the academy, every fireman in Boston had been issued their own bed. It was a complete turnaround, and they spent about $5 million in one stroke of the pen.
That's amazing.
That's Boston.
True story. Check it out.
All right.
I believe you.
A little trivia.
You don't have to say true story when you tell a racist Boston story. It's not like, why, I can't believe it.
Yeah, if they actually shared the mask, you'd have to say true story. Yeah.
Why don't we take a break? Laszlo, we can talk about other stuff. I see you got a sandwich in front of you, so we'll let
you
chomp into that damn thing. And we'll talk about other things.
Certainly.
What's the big news, though? You got Chinatown.
Yeah, Grand Theft Auto Chinatown Wars on the DS there with the dual screen. Maybe if your kid's got a DS, you take it away. Pick up Chinatown Wars?
It was on Xbox, too, right? Why didn't I play this game?
No, Chinatown Wars is just on the DS.
Is just DS.
So what was the one you came in to promote last time?
That was Lost and Damned, our add-on pack for Grand Theft Auto 4. That came out in February.
Yeah, I'm getting a little confused now. Okay.
Oh, they pump it out over there.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, yeah.
I can't keep up with this Rockstar. Right. And thanks for the old-school Rockstar freaking shirt. I'll be wearing that one.
Yeah, man.
You guys should go back to the old logo thing. Nice and simple. Like that hat you got on? That rules. Little R, little star. That's all you need. Rock star. That's what I say.
Star.
More with Laszlo.
Hey, kids. Why spend Saturday watching boring cartoons about fighting aliens when you can help fight real illegal aliens? Head to some real-life Saturday safety fun at Ammunition with Derek the Dodo.
Yay!
Hi, kids. I'm Derek the Dodo. Today, I'm going to teach you all about gun safety. Doesn't that sound fun?
Yay!
Guns can be very dangerous, especially to little people who don't like holes shot in them, or to birds on deserted islands who thought the nice sailors only wanted to be friends. But that's another story.
Derek will teach the kids what to do if they find a gun around the house.
What do we do first?
We pick it up.
Second?
Check is loaded.
Right. Because we don't want any nasty accidents. So look down the barrel and...
pull the trigger!
Yep, it's loaded, Henry. And you made a mess. Next, carefully file off the serial number and conceal it quickly about your person.
Yeah!
Ammunition and Derek the Dodo have been proudly bringing gun safety to your community for over 30 years. Ammunition, protecting your kids' rights.
Ammunition!
Opie and Anthony hanging with Laszlo today. We're going to go back into the tech stuff, but we have to play the story of the day. We have to. Did you see Slumdog Millionaire?
No, but that little girl looks adorable when she's swimming around in her own feces in those slums.
Why didn't you see the best movie of the year?
Because I know what
actually,
slums
Ant didn't
look like
it that much, yeah. Right? You weren't a big fan?
Nah, I thought it was overhyped for what it was. It was okay, but it was, whatever.
Just go and download it for free.
Yeah. I wouldn't pay to see it, but...
Didn't you get it on Netflix?
Yeah, I think so.
Why are people congratulating you about some stock move you made?
Holy Christ. Why? What happened with the...
What happened is that you did an 8-hour show Saturday night from your house, and you were so drunk you forgot what you talked about.
Maybe that's it.
He's revealed his personal finances.
I'll just write some shit down.
Let me check. Hold on. Let me look at this.
It's this.
It could be B.
It's this.
Oh.
Turning this,
yeah,
into supposedly this.
Yeah, that would have been nice if I didn't sell.
Oh, you bailed?
What is it at right now?
Huh?
What is that stock at right now?
I don't know. It's doing okay.
56.
60 cents for Sirius.
Shit.
60 cents for Sirius.
Wow. It was at friggin'...
God, why don't we ever get smart?
I think at its actual, its low of the low, it was like 3 or 4.
That was 60 cents now?
Oh, God.
I got 29,000 shares of it.
Good for you. At what number?
58 cents.
Yeah, look at that.
That's pretty sweet. I think I got mine at like 2 and change.
I could have bought it fucking 3 cents. Well, that's how greedy you get, though.
I bought Sirius 3 times, and every time I bought it, it kept going lower.
Bank of America tanking on me today.
No, but that's how greedy you get. Like, shit. I bought it at like 15 cents, and so it's a great, it's quadrupled almost. And all I think of is greedily, I should have bought it at 3. Like, what a shut up dick.
You'll never get in at the lowest. Yeah. But isn't it amazing? Sell at the highest.
Oh,
so
man,
you
don't
just
be
gotta,
fresh.
You know.
As soon as you understand that, it makes it a lot easier to be in the stock market. But I think we all think the same way as Jimmy.
You want the ultimate low.
The
you
ultimate
want to
low,
buy in.
Right.
And then you want to cash out right before it tanks.
Right. But it's impossible.
60 cents,
doesn't
that's great.
That way.
Yeah, I'm going to buy a shitload of shares today.
Are you?
No.
Then watch it go down.
Yeah, no.
No, I have no
idea.
Did
you get anything for that stock that you turned $100,000?
Citadel? Citadel is now off of the market. It's now what they call the pink sheets.
Right, it's traded in back alleys.
Yeah, it's traded by like 6 people somewhere. And it is sitting at pennies. Just pennies on the fucking dollar.
That's a real story. I can't tell you how many times when I'm out and about doing my thing, people are like, you know, that Citadel story you guys told, that's fake, right? No, it's not. That's exactly what we did to our investment.
It's like at 1 cent or something. It's just been sitting there at a penny, and no one trades it, and it's done.
That's why I stopped buying stock. I'm done. I have a guy that does it.
I am so done.
I got burned so many times. When I was doing the Technofile, you know, I learned about these companies that were just coming out, and I'm like, oh, you know, I'll buy $500 worth of that or $800 worth of that or whatever. And then all the stocks that I thought made sense, like Dell and Microsoft and everything, just over the years has just gone in the shitter.
Tanked.
Give me a little look at BioMirror. BioMirror was supposed to be this company that was going to cure breast cancer. I got in at $14 a share, $11 a share, and then I got in at $4 a share. I got a shitload of this stock.
BioMirror? M-I-R-A?
You got it?
If that's what you said.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, that is it. Now,
what's it doing? Is it good?
Now, as far as curing the breast cancer, this goes back when we were at NEW. Yeah, so I have no idea what this company's about.
I don't think they've done it.
Okay. What are they up to today?
The last trade is at 54 cents.
There you go.
Oh.
And all the data is not available. So.
There you go. And I got I bought a shitload at 14 and 11 especially.
That's cool. On the sheets, back alley trading.
I probably have the worst stock portfolio ever.
Have you taken a beating on a few things?
Oh, look up Dell. What's Dell? I got in at Dell at $52 a share.
Oh, yeah. I think that's where I bought it, too.
Right?
Oh, dumb.
Oh, that was going to, like, double and triple and split and fucking dividends. There was all sorts of stuff going on with Dell. What is Dell at today?
Dell currently, last trade, is at $10.60.
$10.60 a share. That would be, so I got in at 52, and I think I got in a second time at 28. Huh?
Because you're like, oh, this has got to be the bottom.
Yeah. I got to average down. I think I gave people a stock tip with Sirius. I think I, like, told him. Not a tip, but...
Well, you got that inside stuff you know all about, so...
Don't even joke like that.
Dude, you got to be careful about that shit.
I really knew nothing. This is all based on my humble opinion.
Yeah.
I've never heard anything.
Talk around the water cooler says differently, my friend.
What? Are you trying to get the SEC on my ass? Are you crazy?
They know we're a comedy show.
I know nothing about...
Anthony, there actually is nothing to know.
I mean, it was at fucking 15 cents.
Yeah.
And I'm like, take a shot.
Exactly.
I fucking lost money in the market. I'm like, roll the dice. $5,000
That's what it is. I don't even own it.
Right.
I screwed up by not buying when I told everyone they should buy.
You won't even go to the water cooler until there's two of them.
Yes, exactly.
Separate.
Two separate water coolers. Signs over them.
We were just, if the SEC's listening, we were just having fun with Anthony and the inside knowledge.
Because see, they love to go after.
They have a great sense of humor.
All right, here's the Slumdog Millionaire story. It's the story of the day. Fuck Madonna falling off a stupid horse. Yeah. She's fine.
Fuck her and the horse. She, well.
But she'll, milk that shit for a week or so. Here's Slumdog Millionaire and the broad story.
This is 9-year-old Rubina Ali, the childhood star of multi-Oscar winning movie Slumdog Millionaire. Shockingly, Rubina's father has offered up his daughter for adoption in exchange for a payment of £200,000. Here's Rubina at the Oscars in Hollywood back in February with Slumdog Millionaire director Danny Boyle and a co-star. But unbeknown to anyone in the movie industry, Rubina has now been touted for sale to our fake shape reporter by her father and uncles. Rubina's dad, Rafiq, is seen here sat on the right on the sofa during a meeting with the News of the World's undercover reporters in Mumbai last week. The man on the left in the long sleeves is the child actress's uncle, Rajan. It was at this meeting that the pair named their price to our reporters for little Rubina. Later, at another meeting, another of Rubina's uncles, called Mahuddin, told us, "This child is special, an Oscar child." Tragically, charity workers say the racket in children being sold into adoption is rife in India.
All right, I got to be completely honest. That was about a minute.
Yeah.
I have no idea what I just heard because I tuned out.
That's the worst accent.
That's the worst presentation of a news story I've ever heard.
I don't know why they put that bed under it.
Well, it's that delivery and the horrible music behind it.
I did some reading this morning that they're trying to sell the girl for $300,000. I know that much.
Yeah, and some.
But I don't know what the fuck she was saying.
Some news agency set up a hidden camera video thing, and they went to interview the father and the uncle, and that's when they named their prize to this news company. They want like £200,000 for the kid.
Yeah,
they say that they had all kinds of promises made by the movie company that they were going to get him a house and all kinds of stuff, and they just gave him a little money at first. And he says, this is best for everybody. He goes, I got to do what's best for me and my family. He goes, this is best for her because she'll get a better home and we will get money so we can leave the slums.
There is shit going on.
That's what's going on
in the world
there.
We have no idea about.
But Uncle she was Paul, did Uncle Paul put a bid up for
I asked $300,000 what? Money?
I think I got dollars.
I got sardines. My Uncle favorite Paul. Food.
She was barely in the movie. Whatever.
Yeah, which was that? What was that kid?
She was the small version.
Well, she was, yeah. That was
she's 9 years old
standing
now.
Standing out
so.
In the rain. Was that it?
Yeah.
She was like the first one.
Yeah.
Because there was three of each character or something,
Right?
The
second one's probably worth $300,000.
Jesus, man.
The third one. The third one worth a lot more.
Third one was...
Yeah.
Yeah, she was...
That one, I wouldn't pay more than $50,000 for her, to tell you the gods, just to be honest. I'm talking pricing here.
You should put it in a legal bid.
Yeah, I'll put in a bid.
For Chateau Cumia.
50 G's is the highest I'll go for a little
legal,
Indian girl.
Keep
How
legal.
Old is she?
She's 9.
How do you get 9 years?
Yeah. Who
Educate
is that?
Educate her. Make
that
sure
the
she doesn't
girl?
Get fat.
Let me see that picture. You know which one I'm talking about. Yeah. No.
No?
Wow, do we have different tastes? That one.
Yeah, that's the one
yeah,
I would have hit.
That's what I mean. Yeah.
Yeah. How much for that?
That's priceless.
Do you want to go here with the serious? Now, you told people to buy serious because you just said, fuck it. Just give it a shot, right?
Yeah.
Can I go to that call?
Yeah, we got no. There's no issue at all.
I know. I was fucking around. Yeah. I want to make that perfectly clear.
No issues.
I'll break character to make sure these idiots know that. Crotch Critter, Texas. How are you, buddy?
Hey, Hope. Hey, Ant. I wanted to thank Anthony on his in his humble opinion stock tip. I actually took a little bit of a tax return, threw it into Sirius, and I was able to pay off my my home loan of $26,000. Thank you, Ann.
Wow. Nice. Booyah.
Hi, booyah.
Booyah.
The stock is up from when I bought it, 282%.
Wow.
I bought it at very cheap. Again, I was like, I had no faith in the market. And it's almost like it was my attempt at fucking being supportive of the company. I'm like, yeah, fuck it. I'll buy a $5,000 worth. I mean, not that I want to lose that money.
Now be unsupportive and cash out.
Well, I'll see.
Take some profits.
Yeah, it's almost like if I lose that money, it's like, it could, what if it goes up really high? Like, I don't
see,
wanna,
this is, that's the what if. I love the what
this
if.
This is why.
No, actually, if you're supporting the company, then stay in.
Hey,
if you're trading to make some cash, you always pull your profits out. Yeah.
I just got an update on my BioMirror stock. Good news, people.
What do you got, O?
Well,
it's got to be good.
According to Pete in Connecticut, court approves BioMirror's move to the U.S. So this wasn't even a company.
It wasn't even a...
I didn't even know that. And name change to the very easy to remember Oncolthyreon.
Oh, good. That's a lot easier. And when they change the name, you know it's always a good thing.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
They want to sweep that old name under the carpet.
AirTran.
Yeah, AirTran.
Yeah, U.S. Airways.
I say fuck breast cancer drugs today. That's what I say.
Yep. Yeah, that's not going to work out, I don't think.
The news was coming any minute. You love those guys, huh? The boiler room guys. Oh, no, trust me. The news is coming any moment now. I think it's going to happen by Thursday.
The financials are taking a hit today.
Are they?
The financials.
Hey, one more story, and then we go back to tech for a little while, and then we
you do notice
wrap
that
up.
Since we went off fucking terrestrial radio, the stock at Sirius has gone up nicely.
Well, we're responsible for that.
We know why, of course. It's the Opie and Anthony show.
It doesn't hurt.
Of course.
Yeah.
And a little respect in this shithouse.
Let's see what a little company called CBS. Let's look at the 3 month
chart. I hope they delisted.
Let's look at the 3 month chart of that. Well, when did we leave?
March 15th.
All right, March 15th. The stock was sitting
at $9.37.
$3.50.
Uh-huh.
Ha.
What is it now?
Seven.
7 cents?
No, dollars.
Doubled?
Yeah.
I'll tell you one thing, though. Had we not left, it would have been up to like fucking 15 or 20.
That's the one way to look at it.
I love that he could spin anything in this world.
Of course.
Anything whatsoever. Try it. It's fun.
Well, that's the way. That's what's so ridiculous about the market and Wall Street and the mentality down there is that CBS fired all their talent. And all the people in the stock exchange are like, oh, awesome. And then the stock price goes up.
Look at that. They've cut back on spending.
All their good talent nationwide.
They just look at it as they cut back on spending.
They got their cost down.
They got the cost down. But then they'll come out with a statement and say, our advertising dollars aren't as high as they blah, tanks.
Let's do this story. Hulk Hogan. We're doing this because we were supposed to do it Friday, and I think we have an update, so it's worth playing. Hulk Hogan on TMZ. Listen to this.
There was a big controversy that hit the airwaves today about some Rolling Stone magazine interview you did and some comments about O.J. Simpson. Would you care to comment on that?
Well, I spent 3 days with a writer from Rolling Stone talking about being positive and happy and walking in the spirit of Christ. And then he asked me, well, why did you flip out? I said, well, I didn't jump off the Empire State Building. I didn't buy a white Bronco. I didn't do the O.J. Simpson thing. I took the high road. So I guess that's a teaser to sell magazines.
He obviously kind of understands OJ.
Yeah.
But, you know, he wouldn't do that.
That's,
he understands what OJ did.
The old Chris Rock bit.
Yeah.
He goes, I don't.
What was Hulk talking about?
But I understand.
Right.
You heard this, right, Laszlo?
Yeah.
He's like, you know, he drives by a house he's not allowed to be in anymore that he bought with his money and his skills, a mansion. He sees his car driving around town with some young dude in it,
some young buck.
And he knows that young dude is in his bed having sex with his wife or soon-to-be ex-wife. So he basically said, look, I understand what OJ was thinking.
I understand.
And now,
and they make it like it's a big deal. Everybody's thought about killing their woman.
Wow. That's a bold statement.
Find me one man that hasn't for a second thought, if she falls out a window, I will not care for a brief second, and then I'll be sad.
I haven't thought of that yet.
Well, there's been moments where
Ex-girlfriends I have.
That's what I'm saying. Where
I've tried to make it happen.
Right.
There was a time in Turks and Caicos when a certain girl, I'll just say, wanted to try out skydiving.
I was right next to Anthony, so I could back up what he's about to say.
And this was one of those tandem jumps where, you know, you're strapped onto the front of somebody and they jump out the plane, so you don't need any training or anything like that. So the plane takes off. It's over the beach. I see it. I hear a window start. And, no, sorry, that was me. I see the plane. It's way the hell up there, spiraled up to the proper altitude. And I see a little speck drop out of it. And I'm looking, and Ope's right there, looking. And then I see, whoo, a canopy open up.
He got so depressed.
I went like, ugh. I actually went, ugh.
For real.
It would have been such just an easy, you know.
That's like Louis C.K. talked about the fresh start. Everybody deep down thinks about,
yeah.
God, the fresh start. If her plane went down, I'd have a 22-year-old on my arm. And then the plane lands and you get a text, landed safely. Great.
Yeah. Well, mm-hmm. Damn.
Laszlo, what do we got? Stupid you bring planes. Any other tech stuff to the table?
Nah, man.
You didn't really go with it today?
Nah, man. You know, we're working on 3 games at the moment.
Okay.
Sort of buried.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think what I want to know.
Busy with that and tapping my kegs.
You know anything about the new iPhone?
Well, the 3.0?
Yeah, what's that all about?
Mm. I don't know, but I do know that I found out about the iPhone black market the wrong way because my chick's iPhone got stolen. And Apple and the Apple stores, there's a real problem with foreigners coming to the United States and buying as many iPhones as they can and sending them or stealing them and taking them back overseas, unlocking them and selling them for huge amounts of money.
Yeah, like giant.
Like
right?
Insane amounts of money. And so...
why is that, by the way?
Just because it hasn't been released in a lot of places.
Where hasn't it been released that they're selling it?
Russia, I believe.
Yeah, Russia
is one place. Certain places in Asia.
Anyone else notice all the Russians roaming around lately?
It is a little
like
unnerving.
Out of nowhere, it seems like there's a lot more Russians that you have contact with. I'm not saying that's a bad thing. It's just
you
something
have a problem with the Russians?
Not at all, but I've noticed. Am I the only one?
No.
You've seen that, right?
Yes.
But back to your Russian story. I'm sorry.
There's also a really nice Russian mafia contingent in New York.
Yeah.
I'm not true. Saying it's
they're,
a bad
they're
thing.
Not as, just, well, but they're not as polite as the Italian guys were.
Yeah. I just want to know what that's about, because it just seems like the last couple of years especially, there's Russian everything now. Everywhere you look.
They say a lot of iPhones are being stolen. Or outright purchased and then taken to Russia. That I mean, they'll charge you $700 for a replacement. It's nuts.
Who will charge you $700?
I went into the Apple store and they said, first off, they said we don't know if you're eligible for a replacement. I'm like, I have money and I want to buy a device. How am I not eligible for a replacement? They said, well, there's been a lot of problem with people saying that their phone got stolen. And then, you know, just selling it on eBay internationally. Like, here's one that's up on eBay right now, $1,025.
Who's buying that?
A Russian.
Right.
Some Russian dude.
So it's like you steal somebody's iPhone and you put it on eBay for a grand.
Well, fuck that. Why don't you just buy an iPhone and then put it up on, and you're still making a profit. And just do that all day long.
All day long. That's just it. You can't go in and buy a shitload of iPhones. That's what Laszlo is saying.
Oh.
His was lost. He went to go, or
right,
stolen.
I lost it somewhere. So.
Went to go buy one. And they're like, well, I don't think we could sell you one.
What about going to these cell phone stores? They'll sell you an iPhone every day if you
want.
Yeah,
so then I went to the AT&T store, and they said they wanted $500. So it's like somehow the price changed between the Apple store and the AT&T store of $200. So
well, I got an issue there.
Apple wanted $700 fucking dollars?
I couldn't fucking believe it.
How do they want $700?
Well, so you then don't make as much of a profit, so then you're not going into their store every other month and buying another iPhone.
Well, I think that's the unsubsidized price of a 16 gig, because the only reason the iPhones are so cheap when you get a plan is because the AT&T is subsidizing the phone. So if you're not signing a new contract, I mean, that's the cost of a brand new iPhone.
Oh.
No,
No, that's not the cost. That's the amount of profit they're making.
Well, you know what I'm saying. That's what they're charging.
Cost the consumer.
Yeah. But any mobile phone company will do that. Like, I got into a mountain biking accident and fucked up my Verizon phone, and I went and said, I want a new phone. They're like, oh, it's going to be $400. I'm like, what?
For what? That's crazy.
It's fucking ridiculous.
What's the use of having insurance on it?
Insurance is horseshit, too, because then they make you pay a deductible. It's like, but I've been paying every month.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What's your deductible? $700.
Right.
Pay up.
All right, let's do. Like, call your homeowner's insurance. I called them. I'm like, the deductible was the amount of the iPhone. I'm like, yeah. Well, what? I go, so let me claim this. And then on the next one, here's the genius of homeowner's insurance. On the next one, then, you know, I'll be at my deductible. And they're like, no, we're not like medical insurance. They said you have to start over on your deductible each time. I'm like, what?
So you have to lose more than your deductible in order for it to pay for itself.
And every time something gets broken or stolen during the year, if you don't meet the deductible each
time, just lose it.
Insurance enrages me more than any other business.
Yes.
Every month they want that fucking check. And as soon as you go, hey, we've had a little bit of a problem, they're like, hey, go fuck yourself.
Yeah, we run you through hoops.
And what they're doing now after Katrina, because they actually had to pay some money out, is that they're canceling policies all up and down the fucking East Coast.
Oh, yeah, because you're close to the water.
Yeah, they go, we just determined you're in a flood zone.
Yeah, no shit. That's why I need insurance, asshole.
And so, I mean, they're like Allstate, State Farm, they're just canceling people.
That's good news for you. You're saving money on paying
no, the bill. No, if you've got a mortgage, you have to have homeowners insurance. It's such a fucking scam.
The house is gone.
I roll the dice with insurance all the time. Until I finally started making money.
I learned
before
that
you just roll the dice.
If you drop your phone on the toilet and pee on it, the deductible is only $50 for that.
Did you hand it to the guy and go, I pissed on that?
smell it. Go ahead, smell it.
Well, I did have to fill something out online, and I did say they asked for a brief description of what happened, so I just wrote phone fell in the toilet.
How many Guinnesses?
Was drunk.
Were you texting while you were pissing?
I think I was checking email.
Yeah, checking email is now a 24-hour day.
I don't know how many times I've been taking a leak and pull the iPhone out of my pocket and just whoosh right over the toilet.
I hold it away.
It's going to fucking go one of these days.
I hold it away because I know it's going to happen with my big juicy cocks in my hands. I hold it to the left.
What's this coming down the hall? They seem very important.
Oh, there's people in suits and ties. Look at all the suits and ties.
I'll just jerk off and watch them come.
Why do I have to go through airport security when I come into this building?
Don't even get me started.
What is so important?
Don't even get me started. What's in this building?
And why any security that you go through in New York City or at the airport, Anthony and I were talking about this over at his house. It looks like they took a bus through the projects and said, hey, who wants a job? I mean, their name tags are like 18 fucking syllables long. Shaniqua, Nene, Matsuqua. And she's like, you're going to have to lose your water. I'm, what the fuck, you?
And how do they make uniforms that big and shaped like that? Because I have seen some fucking women with the TSA that are bizarre looking shapes. Huge giant asses with the big shelf on the back, and their pants actually fit their TSA pants
perfectly.
Fit them like they had to sew these things.
Yeah,
there's no way she bought that off the fucking rack. Someone had to custom make those pants to fit that atrocity of a body.
We got a couple things going on. We got a guy that sells black market cell phones, and we also have McFly on instant feedback. He lives in the Bronx. I live at the highest point in the Bronx. There's a 30-foot drop to the water, and Allstate said I was in a flood zone.
That's a flood.
Let's see.
There's bigger problems in the world.
Joe, probably not his real name, wants to talk about the black markets and cell phones. Joe.
It is my real name. It's you know, I am not a Russian guy, but I sell, it's called gray market cell phones, actually.
Okay.
So, you know, basically what you do is you buy as many iPhones as you can, and you can ship them overseas, and people pay $600, $800 for it. But the problem is they started selling it with AT&T activation now. So you have to activate the phone in order to buy it. So you have to put a name, a SOSH on it, everything.
Oh, there's the problem.
Mm-hmm. But not if you steal it and unlock it.
Well, stealing it is one thing, but some people don't want to buy a used iPhone. You know, you have to, and every time there's a software update, a you know, the new iTunes comes out, boom, they lock it back up, and then you have to wait for it to get unlocked again. So I can unlock it, too, but they lock it back up so often.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, with the updates, anytime you go to do an update, it
any single time.
Yep. Takes up the
Have you had any iPhones come through with a sticker of a cat on the back? Because that's my chick's.
I need it back.
I've seen fake ones. I have seen fake ones, too. And
it's just nothing inside.
It's spelled iPhone plaster.
It's spelled EYE phone. EYE if it's a pirate. Are you going, sir?
Can I interrupt for a second? Jimmy, can you help me out? Sure. These guys look very important. Can you open the studio door and just yell, "Who the fuck are you?"
I wouldn't do that.
Why? Why?
I just wouldn't do that.
Why?
They all have suits red, on and their I'm hands red are on
flagging.
Their chin.
Red flagging.
I'm red flagging.
Jimmy, would you do that for,
no.
for us? No.
Right. No.
Hi.
Do you guys have a demerit system over here now or something?
Well, we
you
have
talking about the red flags.
No, it's a paddle.
No, it's
you
a paddle.
You ever eat at the Brazilian steakhouse?
Yes.
Where you get meat until you turn that paddle to red?
That's right.
We have a green side and a red side, and if we're talking about something company-related or
something
we think
might
it's going to be
scary.
Bad, like Opie starts talking, I'll hold the red up, and it's like, just stop talking about that. It's a pre-dump button, which I like to think about.
Hey, what a great time to do the curtain closing gag.
I've held the...
Oh, true.
I've held the freaking red paddle for you, too, my
friend. I know. I've red paddled myself
many
times.
This doesn't go one
way. Ooh, feels good.
They look really important.
What a great time to do that.
Look at the one guy. He's got the two fingers up on his cheekbone and the rest on his chin.
He's like, well...
I see.
It's that very interesting look.
He's looking at the most important room in this place, by the way, and he's probably thinking, oh, we could turn that into a conference room for our new company.
Maybe these are people from Liberty. I don't know.
Oh, my God.
From Liberty Medical.
Jimmy,
for diabetes supply.
What, the guys that own part of the...
Could be.
That's what's great about, you guys got this big staff, and they're quite nervous. They walk around like they're line items in a spreadsheet that some guy upstairs is fucking just going, delete,
they
delete.
Are. That's why.
Well, the number at the bottom right keeps going up.
You see Steve with the Bluetooth yet?
Oh,
he's never worn a Bluetooth in his life, but all of a sudden he's wearing a Bluetooth, and he's running around the hallways.
I don't like the fact they're looking at that main control room.
No, that's not good.
And these here are what you could use to remove.
This could be. Here they come.
Oh, boy.
Can they hear us out there?
No.
Oh, yes, they can. The computer's on.
Oh, they can?
Wow.
They're probably like, who is this bombing show?
Hello, gentlemen.
Why does he keep touching his face?
This isn't good. They're explaining this is the Opie and Anthony show, and the looks we're getting from the very important looking people.
Do they need so many flat screen televisions? We could cut costs by removing some flat screen.
They're explaining how this would be a great place for a new bathroom. Here's the things we could do with this room.
The executive washroom.
It's already pretty much a toilet.
Once these worthless losers are vacated.
Jimmy, why don't you politely ask them who they are? I don't think that's out of line.
What happened? Nah, they all have suits on. They have short haircuts.
Steve, in with them. Like
Steve.
Steve does not fit with them.
All right, they're passing our studio.
Steve, any info?
Why are you following them around?
Steve, who was that?
Why are you following them? Who are they?
Who are they? Anybody know?
They're making us nervous.
Paul, you know? Wait, Paul knows? Paul, just yell it.
Who are they? We're nervous.
Yeah.
The three on the left were really high executives, and then he didn't say who the two on the right were.
High executives in this company?
Yeah, and then they got some meeting at 10:30. There's groups of them all over the place.
Do they need to come in here and straighten anything out?
Is there some kind of board meeting or something today? Yeah,
it must be another axing coming around. I have no idea.
Earnings call something? What do we got going on? Kenny, you know anything?
No,
I know we don't have you on the air anymore because we're keeping it very professional with you. But
those people were staging in the conference room.
Mm-hmm.
And I noticed that in the office next door to the conference room, there was another meeting going on.
Were they removing the Opie and Anthony logos from everything? That's all we need to know.
Yeah, that's all. When we start seeing that, that's a sure sign.
Imagine one of the guys in the suits has a razor. He just
starts to the new logos that are on the glass.
But can you imagine, like, all those guys in suits, and all of a sudden they say, Jim Norton, report to the conference room. And I walk in and sit down, and they go, all right, what is it you do here? Tell jokes.
What would you say your job is? What do you do here?
I was in one of those meetings.
I tell dick jokes.
I'm a people person.
Yeah, that's they were.
Yes, Kenny.
Real execs.
I was asking around about these people. Nobody seems to want to commit to who they actually are.
Oh, they're just executives.
The Illuminati.
They're not G-men.
That happens.
There it is, Danny.
quite frequently with like potential investors and salespeople.
Yeah,
and, like,
I'll give you the other side of the story. I saw Blatter, and he looked really like out of sorts today. I'm like, "All right." He goes, "Yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah." Well, I won't be around at 11, so I'll just see you tomorrow.
Got white powder under his nose.
he's in the meeting with the person in the office next to the conference room.
Oh, no. We're going to miss you, Steve.
You know what was a bit nerve-wracking is the one guy who kept touching his chin and rubbing it, which means he's like making that. Mental decisions.
He's deciding things.
Right. Either that or his chin itches.
I hope Jimmy's right.
I know.
But Laszlo makes a good
he's
point.
He's got chin warts.
When you put the two fingers on your cheek and then the rest on your chin, you're
rubbing it. You're going,
what can I do with
this? I can do this or this.
Nope. Hands on the face, sign of discomfort. It's a protective thing. Sign of that you're uncomfortable at times as well. So it doesn't have to be.
Not to the side, though. To the side is you're thinking.
That's tough.
Yeah, they're probably potential investors.
Would they go down the hall to look at the old channel?
Exactly. And you could see that, you know, certain health insurance issues we have with the studio.
They can cut back on
holy shit.
Yeah, there's a reason health insurance is so expensive here.
We got some Mickey Rourke audio.
Oh, yeah, he was annoyed.
And we got unlucky lottery. Which one's worth doing here, Dan?
Well, I haven't heard the Mickey Rourke, and the unlucky lottery, I'm not sure if it's unlucky lottery or sucks to be you.
We're starting to think that's the same thing, right?
I'm not sure which it is.
It's just a good story.
It's no, there is a subtle difference.
It's a quickie if you want to go with it.
Okay, we'll do that.
What's subtle the subtle difference? Unlucky lottery is when something happens to you that the odds of it happening are so astronomical that the same odds, in a good way, you would have won Lotto.
Right.
It's like, why didn't I win Lotto? Like, let's say, I always use this example, a boulder that is sitting on the top of a mountain and has been there. Dinosaurs saw this rock in the same place. And as your car is driving by, it decides for some reason to dislodge and crush you and your family. That's unlucky lottery because the odds are astronomical.
Sure.
Sucks to be you.
Is the boulder, because he's minding his business, and all of a sudden, now he's rolling down a hill into a car.
I was sitting up here comfy for a millennium. It sucks to be you is just bad things that happen. It doesn't necessarily have to be out of the realm of possibility. You get hit by a bus, and the rear tire goes right up the middle of you, and your brains are in the street. That's a sucks to be you, but it does happen.
But couldn't that be unlucky lottery? Because that type of thing's going to happen, and the odds are very astronomical.
Let's say you're on a dirt road in the middle of nowhere, and a lost bus runs you over. That would be unlucky lottery. If you're in the city crossing the street, it's not unlucky lottery. See, there is a subtle difference.
Well, I think this is going to fall into the sucks to be you category.
All right. All right, we'll decide, Daniel.
Yeah, thanks a lot for making assumptions. Why even fucking play it now, Dan?
A woman who was killed in a collision with a tow truck in British Columbia last month appears to have been killed by her laptop computer. The authorities say Heather Story's laptop was not secured in the backseat of her car, and the force of the accident caused it to fly forward and hit the back of her head.
Wow. What we believe has happened is she was struck in the back of her head and neck with this laptop computer. She simply didn't have it secured within the confines of her car, and it's ultimately been the instrument of her death.
Oh, EMT ran over to her and hit control alt delete.
Come on. Hey, what is this?
Hey, she got the blue screen of death, everybody.
That's, that's right down the middle. That's a tough call. Because people are killed by projectiles in their vehicles,
sure.
But I don't know.
Not
that
your own laptop.
Suck. Yeah, your laptop hitting you in the head.
Can I tell you my second grade teacher died?
Oh, no.
She was in Canada.
You're kidding.
And she was beheaded.
No. Really?
By a snowplow.
Jesus.
Get out of here.
Snowplow accident. The guy had the plow up through the windshield. There goes my second grade teacher.
Oh my God.
Well, that's fast anyway.
And the principal had to tell us little fuckers.
Oh, you were that?
He told you the details?
Yes. Why? How else do I know?
Why would he
I didn't Google her name 20 years later.
You could have said just in a horrible, tragic accident, nope. Your teacher's dead.
We got the details.
You had to say that our head was cut off by a snowplow?
That was what up in the morbid... in the opposition.
What was your principal's name? Club Soda Kenny?
Yeah.
And now, kids, yes. How your teacher died.
She has to be buried in two separate boxes.
My principal ended up dying before we graduated sixth grade, too.
What happened to him?
He,
the casino?
No, I heard diving accident out in Wading River. Or Riverhead. Riverhead's inland, so Wading River area.
Is your school cursed?
I don't know.
Jeez.
Diving out on the Long Island Sound is a little crazy, right?
Yeah, where'd they build your school? On a fucking Indian burial ground?
We had a... They didn't remove the bodies, though, only the tombstones from the top.
Uh-huh, oh, my God. When I'm not doing Pathmark commercials, I'm here in a graveyard.
I love when he curses in movies, the Pathmark guy. Yeah. Because it always reminds me of, like, and ground beef on sale here at fucking Pathmark.
Yeah, that's right.
Holy shit, look at the prices of potatoes.
These tacos look just like cutlets, don't they, kids?
He's a potty mouth in movies.
Oh, no.
The Pathmark man.
Hi,
dude.
Charles Rodden.
Yeah.
We're the best at visual bits on the radio. I'm proud of that.
When we were little tater tots
in
elementary school, our gym teacher, I remember him, he signed up to go into the Army.
Oh, shit.
And he came back to the school after basic training in his Army uniform and everything. And he came into the cafeteria, and everyone was applauding. And he was just standing there. And I remember, you know, everyone standing up applauding. And he got this big smile on his face. And, Opie, why don't you just guess how this one ends?
How many limbs was he missing?
No.
It wasn't
not
limbs?
Even that good. We weren't even able to say hello to him ever again. Charlie Dunn took him away from the school. He went to the NOM and didn't come back.
Oh. I missed the story. I thought he came back from NOM and got the big applause and there was something horrifically wrong with him.
He went through basic and then he came back to the school to like say hi. Mm-hmm. And there was a whole big thing like.
And here comes, gym teacher. I don't
even remember his name.
He's an American hero.
Yes, he's been through basic, and he's going to help defend this great country of ours and spread freedom throughout the globe. Let's hear it for him.
And there we were, all our little kids clapping.
Off to Korea, yay.
And then, well, Korea, why you? Was the tail end of the NOM.
This is like a Wonder Years plot. Are you sure this actually happened?
No, I swear it did. It did. It was the gym teacher.
Did you go to school with Winnie?
And Winnie Cooper. I kissed Winnie Cooper on a rock.
I'm there.
Yeah, and
kid wore the Jets jacket because supposedly it was one of our school's aunt.
Really?
From our old neighborhood, like Stimson Junior High or something like that.
Well, if it was Timber Point, Boomer Esiason could have punched him in the face. Yeah.
So he didn't make it?
Or farted on him. Nah, he...
Charlie got him.
I wish sucks. I could remember his name, so maybe I could, you know, check it out on the wall.
That's Winnie Cooper?
Little Winnie Cooper.
Cooper's here?
Yeah, she's got a nice pooper.
I love her car. It's a
Cooper's
BMW.
Cooper's pooper?
Cooper's pooper.
Oh, God. I heard that bomb, Jimmy.
I thought Winnie Cooper, the tie-in, would get a big laugh.
I'd like...
What's the standing one?
I like Cooper's pooper better, though.
It's kind of nice. Let me see. Get a little view of Winnie.
Come on, let's see her shit.
She actually became like what? She went to college and
she's a brainiac,
math whiz or some shit.
Yeah,
yeah. She's there. It is.
What's she doing now? She married?
All right.
Yeah, I think so.
Oof.
That's not too shabby.
But I think that's kind of a few years back already. That Stuff magazine spread. Because I think she's a lot older than that.
Wouldn't mind making French onion soup in her box.
Oh, would that be nice?
Would you blow a load in her fart box?
In her pussy, without a fucking, no pill, no nothing. Keep it natural.
Of course. That's what you're going to do. Jesus. I'm supposed to do.
The pill. What are we, fucking heathens?
It is that. That's my religion.
God wants a baby, we have a baby.
I'll
correct myself. God wants a baby, you have a baby.
God wants a baby,
handle
I'm kicking down the stairs.
Exactly.
Let's do a little Mickey Rourke, and then we're getting out of here. I think we did fine for a Monday. Should have left 20 minutes ago.
Certainly did do fine.
This is what Mickey Rourke is saying today.
Who's the guy that made fun of my dog?
He's not here.
Not here.
Who's that guy, Joel McRae at Talk Soup? He's going to get a slap in the face.
McRae?
He made fun of my dog who died, this little...
Have you got any
when
more
did
dogs?
Sinatra
yeah, I got
come
four
back
more,
to
but
life?
It wasn't nice. Yesterday I was shaving. I was here and I'm making jokes about my dog dying, so I'm, you know, that ain't right, you know? Little if you see him, tell him he's going to get a smack in the face.
Oh. Ooh.
How am I supposed to go from an up-tempo number to listening to him talking about a goddamn dog dying?
He stopped himself.
Where are those pictures
there?
I was supposed to see?
He's going to get a slap in the face.
I'm going to kick his... shin.
I have to get a. We have to do a picture before I go. Just remind me.
For what?
Of.
For what?
Of.
The three of us.
No, I didn't shower today.
Why?
Because I need one. No. It has to be done.
No. Poor Kay.
Why don't you tell me ahead of time? I didn't even shower today.
That's
I got
fine.
Bedhead.
Bedhead's fine. Put it on.
Let E-Rock take it. It'll be all blurry.
Yeah.
Won't see shit. Blurry, grainy. He could take the best camera ever and turn it into a piece of shit.
Because he's a fucking lumpy nothing.
You give him a great camera. He takes a picture. It's grainy and blurred.
He's fucking horrible. He couldn't take a picture of the Earth with the Hubble. Fucking blithering idiot. Oh, I didn't realize you're not supposed to have your hat in front of the lens. Dumb cunt.
Just fucking mayo smear on the lens.
Oh, he has fucking stinks at picture taking.
Yeah.
Oh, he's
horrid.
Fucked me. He's fucked me good on like getting
right,
a picture
see?
With a celebrity.
Yeah.
I get it back. It looks like Michael J. Fox took it. Like,
yeah.
What the fuck? Stand still, motherfucker.
The guy shakes like, wow, is that
that was
wow. Who is that?
You got us going for a second.
Now it's yeah. just somebody?
Well, let's just see the somebody.
Because that somebody had a nice,
it's,
with
it's
the
totally
cold,
not her face.
Shitter.
No, I mean, it's completely someone different.
Yeah.
Let's get out of here.
Boiled down.
All right,
man.
Guys.
What a fun Monday.
Laszlo, the big
fun
plug,
day.
Grand Theft Auto,
yes,
Chinatown.
For the Nintendo dual screen, the DS. There's now the DSi is out. It's another DS. But Grand Theft Auto Chinatown Wars, go to Amazon, GameStop, pick it up. It's like the old, you know, GTA 1 and 2 that had the sort of top-down view. Of
yeah,
the, of
the... so much more stuff to do, and it's a lot edgier. I like the drug dealing and stuff like that. It is fun to buy and sell and trade drugs. For money.
With a little stylus.
Yes, of course.
But it's cool. It, like, there's flamethrower missions and all the stuff
can't
that you love about causing havoc.
Yeah.
Love the flamethrower.
All right. I think that's it for today. Thanks, guys.
Yeah? Is that how...
Let's go into this. Let's bust into this meeting with these suits and just rub our chins.
Yeah. We'll show them.
That's right. We don't like suits around here, man.
Man.
Yeah, the guy was a bit distracting.
Yeah,
he
right.
was doing some heavy
let him,
thinking.
Let him do his work.
All right. We'll do that. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Laszlo, thank you. It's a pleasure,
thank you.
Buddy. All right.